Yes, quickly, Dominic.
Hi, Robin. Hi, Howard.
That's Howard you're talking to.
Yeah, you're talking to Howard.
Hi, Robin. Hi, Howard. Hi, Fred. Hi, Jackie. Hi, Billy. Hi, Thompson.
All right, quickly, yes.
We didn't play cards.
He's on a sugar high.
We didn't play cards
because you're a chump.
Don't be mad at me. I was in the middle of...
This guy's a real wise guy. I'll take this up on the air with you another time if I was in a rush.
All right. I want to tell you about a study that we did.
All right.
For Geraldo's show with jurors.
Quickly.
The reason they say this is done psychologically, that black jurors are voting not guilty, is that the Afro-American today feels so disenfranchised with the system, without jobs, without money for education, that it's their last place of protest.
Let me tell you something.
Well,
that's a load of bull.
The protest. You don't protest when people don't get it.
It's the last place.
Let me tell you something.
Let
me tell you something. You're right. You know what? You want to know something? You're absolutely right. You're way of pissing off the white man. And let me tell you something.
Not white man, society.
You know all these Koreans who come over here. You think the white people like the Koreans? You think the white people? What do you think? What do you think? Do you think the Christians liked when the Jews were in a ghetto and that they would put in the newspaper no Jews allowed to work here? Listen, black community has got to go out. Create jobs for itself, create work. You can do that. You start businesses. What do you think? You think these Koreans that come over here, they got a pot to pee in? Come over here. They open up a friggin' grocery store.
I don't think it's the same thing for them. But
now, of course it's the same thing. You're going to sit and whine about, the white man won't give. Forget the white man already. Pretend the white man isn't here. But he isn't here. He's not had nothing to do with you. Go out and make something of yourself.
The African American.
And you make something of yourself, Dominic.
Yeah, I'm trying.
Dominic, better yet, am I right? You lawyers can go through any amount of money, am I correct?
When you walk in, I can tell you what's in your pocket.
Exactly. Thank you. Dominic Barber, the great Dominic Barber. He is one of the greatest at knowing what's in your pocket.
Don't be mad at me. Come on.
I am not mad. No one could ever be mad at you.
All right, bye-bye.
All right. He's in a new movie, by the way, Natural Born Eaters. You're going to love it. Hey, Dominic tried out for a movie. Do you know about this?
You did tell me, but nobody else knows.
I tried out for the new Al Pacino movie.
Let me tell you what happened.
It's not a setup from you.
Were you in love interest?
I tell you, I'm in two parts. I actually met with...
He was big enough for two parts, they said, when they met him.
You haven't seen me, but I'm looking very good.
Let me tell you what happened. Our agent...
Dominic.
Our agent, yeah, right.
Super agent.
In fact, they want to give him the part. Did you hear about this?
No.
Dominic, do you know they want to give you the part?
No, are you kidding?
I'm not kidding, but they say the movie's not in Cinerama, so they don't know if they can fit you on the screen.
Super Agent Don Buchwald
heard there was a call for... they need a big fatso for a movie. To play, what do you play, an Italian?
I play a lawyer-type real estate developer. It's a new movie called The Mayor.
You don't play it. You didn't get the part yet.
Lawyer-type real estate developer.
So that's right.
He calls me up. He goes, I know you're setting me up. I go, what do you mean? He goes, you got a camera that's going to be there, and I'm going to audition for a part, and you guys are goofing on me. So, I said, listen, Al Pacino's cake. I don't know anything about this. I am busy working on my own film. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Because if you guys have set me up, I'm going to kill myself.
So he went out there and he auditioned, and God only knows if he'll get this part. If he does, it'll be unbearable.
But let me ask you a question. Why did I have to do an audition in a bathing suit?
They should have a love interest for you, a cannoli. All right, I got to go. Dominic Barbara, movie star and lawyer.
Yes.
And frequent Geraldo guest.
Seems like a Geraldo regular,
yeah. Geraldo and me and four people did a study.
A study, yeah, he was in a laboratory.
And we,
you know what they did? Geraldo got in front of the audience and said, how many people here go on juries and to piss off white people? And he stood up.
Stand up. That's what he always does. He counts the bodies.
Thank you for the study.
A woman who fled naked from a burning house.
Wow.
Told Fort Worth police.
Cool.
She was held as a sex slave for more than 14 hours before freeing herself by using a lighter to burn through the duct tape that bound her.
Cool.
Firefighters saw her dashing nude from the house. Jailed on kidnapping and sexual assault charges are Thaddeus and Karen Moyer.
I would like to represent them. Hey, that must have been a burning bush.
The 44-year-old victim,
naked woman burning bush, get it?
Was abducted from her disabled car in a parking lot. She had to be treated for bites and other injuries.
Hmm. Turns me on.
Isn't that weird? You know, your car breaks down and two people approach. You think they're coming to help you. And the next thing you know, you're duct taped to a bed.
Gee, thanks for the help.
It's amazing what's going on.
Do it.
Marlon Brando has written a book. A review in USA Today says that Marlon should have tried harder. He doesn't mention any of his wives or his children.
Of course. These guys are all, I don't know, they claim he got a $5 million advance. Who would give him that kind of money? Who even cares about him anymore? It's Marlon Brando.
I don't know. They do say there are some insights that he delivers about what it was like to work on certain movies, but he's not really forthcoming about who he is as a human being.
Plus, he wrote the book in crayon. My new paperback is chock full of good stuff, written with a pen and paper.
Also, there's a new book on Princess Grace that says she wasn't a very happy camper.
I didn't know she was into camping.
The book is called Grace by Robert Lacey. Says that she had mood swings and her weight gain made her intolerably difficult. At home with her husband.
Does it say what she was better at, camping or driving?
The bloom had come off the rose of that fairy tale princess marriage, and she had to keep young men around.
She is the light of fun.
To make her still feel young and beautiful. So apparently, Princess Grace was not very happy. At the time of her death.
Stand up if she thinks she's happy. Stupid show.
She confided to one friend that when she had this young suitor, she thought he'd hate her lumps and bumps. But she said he didn't seem to mind at all.
Lumps and bumps.
She did have many, many premarital affairs, so she was no virginal princess.
Yeah. We did a study. She wasn't a virgin. She was made with boobs. She couldn't even drive her car. As fat as I am, I could drive my car. Probably hit the steering wheel with her belly. Because I got the Mercedes convertible. Jessica Hankin.
Meryl Streep believes in Shirley MacLaine's psychic ability. She says that... Several years ago, when she was buying a home, McLean predicted the quake that hit Los Angeles. She did that while they were making postcards from the edge.
Ooh, super.
She had just moved to Los Angeles from Connecticut, and even though she said she loved living there, she was worried about earthquakes. McLean said, "How long do you plan to be out here?" She said she didn't know, maybe about 2 years at the most. And McLean told her, "You're in good shape because the big one won't hit until 1994 in the winter."
And a study was performed. It was revealed up.
McLean says the next big one is due in November of 1995.
Actually, the earthquake was caused by me jogging in the neighborhood.
Rachel Hunter, the 24-year-old wife of Rod Stewart,
I'm representing her.
Given birth
to me, darling. I look like I gave birth.
A 7-pound, 14-ounce baby boy.
I just gave birth to a cannoli.
They say after just 45 minutes of labor. His name, Liam McAllister Stewart.
What about Dominic? Dominic Liam Allister McStewart. I would like to represent him in the divorce.
Look at the kind of advice 17 Magazine has been dispensing. This magazine is 50 years old now. In 1946...
This is from a study?
No. They told girls, do point out Johnny's best features. Say something like, you have hands like a doctor, strong and efficient.
Oh, I know what this is. I read this study.
This is not a study. This is what 17 Magazine used to advise girls to do to catch guys.
Yeah, it works.
Don't ever let your irritation show on your face. When you're angry, sit still, be quiet, smile if possible, and start the conversation moving in the right direction by saying, I'm sorry.
And don't light your farts.
That was 1946 for girls. In 1968, they said, don't lose your virginity. Almost all girls who do come to regret it.
Whatever you do, don't lose your virginity. So my wife met me, she complimented me on my hands and then told me I had a stomach like Delaware. She's a woman for me.
In the 80s, they said, do stop looking to guys as your only source of excitement and self-esteem. And don't drink and drive.
What?
And don't drink and drive.
What's the fun of that?
That's right.
Jackie,
it's all
healthy.
You might
hit
a bump and spill
your
drink.
If you drink and drive, I could represent you.
And the watchword for the 90s is to consider volunteer work.
You did a study?
No. Just read 17 men.
I need them all. They don't do a study.
And finally this morning, this is a terrible story out of Phillipsburg.
You want my advice? Bend over.
School officials, Howard, are forming an anti-hazing policy after several varsity cheerleaders reportedly urinated on squad mates.
That's funny.
As an initiation rite earlier this summer. They're continuing to investigate the incident that allegedly occurred in late June while the team was attending a cheerleading camp at the Kutztown University.
What were they taught with?
You're saying girls urinated on guys?
Yes, there was...
Or another girl?
There was action taken against several girls, but they were not expelled from school.
I would kill to see that. I really would. I swear, to see cheerleaders going to the bathroom on other cheerleaders in a hazing ritual? I would go absolutely... Is that a turn-on, guys, or what?
Stop it.
Oh, come on. How do they know it wasn't an accident? I mean... Maybe they couldn't aim good.
Oh.
Maybe they were just missing the ball.
Why would they hit another girl when they were in the bathroom?
I don't know. Sometimes I go, I accidentally go on Fred's foot.
Yeah, but men have a different apparatus.
That's true. That's maybe you got a point there, Robin. Sexist.
Get to the sexism chapter.
What? I just can't believe it was girls when, you know, I first heard it. Three cheerleaders have been removed from the team as a result.
Did they eat asparagus beforehand?
The urination was preceded by other forms of hazing, such as spraying...
Spraying?
Spraying shaving cream in the girls' faces.
I can't find it until I pee.
And putting butter in their mouths.
2, 4, 6, 8, where do we urinate?
Whoa. Clothes were taken away from the initiates while they were showering, so they would have to run naked down the hall
cool.
to retrieve them. And the girls who urinated on the initiates were a senior and a junior.
What's wrong with that if they both consent?
Well, the younger girls aren't consenting. They're being harassed.
Yeah, but that's part of joining the club.
Here we go, urine. Here we go.
And here's exactly what I was about to say. The targets of the hazing were not warned in advance what form the hazing would take. So maybe you agreed to a few hijinks, but you didn't know it would include urination.
Cheryl, she's our man. Use her like a urinal can. I know cool
they
hazing rituals.
They were blindfolded.
The only thing weird about this is that girls are doing it to girls. It used to be college. You know what college guys do? They put you in a room, and like all the college guys... urinate in the room, all right? So when you walk in,
you know
something's going on.
Yeah.
So what they do is they blindfold you and tie you to a chair. I know guys who did this. And while they're sitting there, you take hot dogs and you put it near the guy's mouth. Now the whole room stinks from urine,
yeah.
And there's a hot dog near the guy's mouth, and you rub it in his face and stuff. And he thinks it's no hot dog.
Oh.
And the guy usually vomits.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Well, I've heard the one where they take the guys into the toilet.
Yeah.
And the toilet is kind of stinky.
Right.
And they have a candy bar in the bottom of it.
Right.
And they make the guys reach in blindfolded.
And get it out.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Tell the story when you did the number two on the with the wrestling wrestling coach, Jackie. Just kidding. Of course, it didn't happen.
They do have a rumor floating around that... there were pictures taken. But they don't know whether that's a fact or not.
That could be a study.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a study, yes.
That's a study?
That's a study, yes. Yeah, that's a study, yes. Your Honor, we have a study.
The girls were blindfolded, and they didn't know until after it happened what was going to happen to them. Other girls were kept out of the room.
Let me say this. I will pay good money for those photographs.
Oh, dear.
Where was this done?
In Phillipsburg, wherever that is.
Well, Gary, get me a number for Phillipsburg. Yeah. Let's call.
It's across from Easton, Pennsylvania,
Cutstown.
I think, in New Jersey.
Cutstown?
Cutstown University.
Cutstown.
Cutstown.
Yeah, Cutstown. Okay, give me a phone number of the school. I'll call and ask if I can negotiate the price of the pictures of the girls. Hello, this is Howard Stern.
Dominic Barber's dramatic SOS in Long Island Sound caught on tape. And only Howard 100 News has its hands on the actual Coast Guard audio of the heart-stopping distress call. Listen to this.
These guys tracked down Dominic's Mayday call.
Oh, that's great.
Can you believe this? Here we go.
Mayday, 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 Mayday.
Coast Guard Station Center, go ahead, over.
Vessel in distress, this is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound. What is your position, over?
55, 622, 7335, 418. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire. I shut it down. I see another boat coming over. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire.
Is that Dominic giving his measurements or?
Fire!
Vessel in distress, this is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound, over.
I'm on fire!
Roger, Captain. How many persons on board, over?
All by myself. I'm on fire!
Did you hear the Coast Guard guy yell out, get off your fucking radio so we can answer you?
Yeah, he's not letting up that little button. Is that what it is?
He doesn't know how to work any of the equipment on the boat. If anybody should have his boat taken away, it's him.
Hey, you know what?
I've seen the guy. Let me just say something. I've seen this fucking guy drive that boat. He can't drive it.
I've seen it, too. It's awful.
Artie was with me. We saw him drive over a rowboat with a guy in it.
A dinghy. Killed the motherfucker.
Yeah, I mean, it came that close to chopping a guy's head off. We went by some nuclear sub area on the Long Island Sound.
We really did.
And Dominic went too fast, and the Coast Guard pulled him over because he was disobeying the speed limit.
He was creating a wake and a no wake.
No, I'm sorry, but we're trying to get to Foxwoods. Officer.
Doesn't he understand that that's an emergency?
It's an emergency. Howard needs to gamble at the Foxwoods.
Yeah, well, didn't you see it says turn off your engine and go slower? So then, then the guy, can you picture this guy? He's 900 pounds. He's in on his boat. Why is he in his underpants? I don't even know. Who drives a boat in their underpants?
Oh, my God.
And then the guy, his boat's on fire.
That's Mayday. I'm in my underpants.
You know Mayday. I have no pants on. I'm on fire.
They should put do the Springsteen song. They should do a parody where I'm on fire.
Mayday. Help me. Help. Somebody say something.
I'm on fire.
Tell that fat fuck to turn off his thing so we can talk to him.
Mayday!
They shouldn't just let him burn up. Listen to that annoying guy. Let him keep saying Mayday over and over again.
Mayday!
Coast Guard Station Center, go ahead, over, Captain.
Vessel in distress, this is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound. What is your position, over?
55, 622.
Yeah, that's his measurements.
7335 418. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire. I shut it down. I see another boat coming over. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire. I'm on fire.
Vessel in distress. This is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound. Over.
I'm on fire. Look it off.
Roger, Captain. How many persons on board? Over.
I'm all by myself. I'm on fire!
Get him off the boat.
Permanently. I'm on fire! Yeah, little girl, if you're dead at home, little girl. I'm on fire!
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 Dominic is so dramatic.
Yeah. He was fine. And he's in his underpants, and then someone pulls over, and his schlong is hanging out of his underpants.
Mayday, Mayday! Mayday, Mayday! 75, 14, 58!
And he's you know he has probably the coordinates wrong. And he's so fat, I know when he drives the boat, it's like his arms can barely hold the steering wheel, and and he's not even looking.
That's how the dinosaurs died. Yeah. They couldn't reach their mouths anymore to feed themselves. Does any boat guy know what the fuck all that means? What's your position? 55! 86-49.
Can you imagine him flying a plane?
I'll give you a free divorce. I'll let you use my house on Shelter Island.
Woody, I'll see you out there. That's a great piece of tape. Thank you.
By the way, Howard 100 News saluting the United States Coast Guard in New Haven for providing that audio tape.
All right, thank you very much. That's Steve Langford.
Mayday.
What's your position?
Mayday.
180.
Fire! I'm on fire. 180, 45, 572, 62, 54. Hike.
Okay, Dominic, what is it?
Mayday, mayday.
Do you actually have the tape?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're kidding me.
You missed it?
No. Mayday, 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 mayday.
Third station center, go ahead, over, Captain.
Vessel in distress, this is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound. What is your position, over?
55, 622, 7335, 418. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire. I shut it down. I see another boat coming over. I'm on fire. The boat is on fire. The boat is on fire.
See how annoying you are?
Wait a minute.
What?
You can't play that tape.
I say can.
No, I'll tell you why.
Why?
Under the Terrorism Act, what I didn't tell anyone was I was out there doing special surveillance for the government.
be quiet.
In your underwear.
In your underpants.
Wait a minute.
Murder.
And meanwhile, if you listen to the rest of it, the guy yells at you and says, well, turn. Because he goes, we can't answer you. You won't shut the fuck up.
Now, let me ask you a question. Does that sound like some elitist, or is that just every man scared to death?
That sounds like an elitist. That sounds
right.
Like a guy.
Who else is on a boat going Mayday?
Who has a boat who doesn't know how to drive it.
Well.
All right, goodbye.
Mayday, 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 mayday.
Start station center. Go ahead, over, Captain.
I'm on fire.
Vessel distress. This is Coast Guard Sector Long Island Sound. Over.
I'm on fire.
Captain, how many persons on board? Over.
I'm all by myself. I'm on fire. I'm on fire. Fire.
Come on, Dominic, one more.
Fire!
That's it. Keep going.
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Yeah.
Fire! Fire!
I got a bad desire.
Fire.
Nice. And there's a whole bunch of, and then there was this one.
I'm all by myself.
Yeah. I'm all by myself. I'm all by myself.
There you go.
Yes.
And you look great.
Thanks.
You really do. I mean, you're not a good-looking guy. Don't get me wrong. But I tell you something, you look a lot better with hair than you did when you were bald.
I know.
And you know, Scott has that new sexy intern.
Oh,
she's,
yeah.
She's, imagine if I had to.
So Scott, you know, he makes sure now that his hair looks good.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's the whole combing thing. His hair especially well.
Oh, yeah.
It looks great.
Notice how attentive he is to his hair. Did your wife give you any problem on the fact that you have a female intern?
I told you no.
Really?
No, not at all.
Good. Okay.
She didn't hear yesterday's show?
No. No, but I told her.
Yeah, what'd you tell her?
I said, I have a female intern, a nice, beautiful 22-year-old.
Yeah.
Really?
She said,
what?
So?
What?
No, not at all.
All right. Scott, I hate your radio voice. I really hate when you go, not at all. It's like...
He has a radio voice. Yeah. Did you notice?
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Men's hair now is so good. This Dermabond technique, I was not really a person who believed that you could put something on your head and get your original hairline back and make it look so natural that you couldn't tell the difference. I'm now a believer.
You know, I can't remember what Scott looked like bald now.
Yeah, well, Scott was one of those guys who was really bald. And
very
a lot
bald.
Of the people who go to Men's Hair Now, you're talking about people who really have no hair left. And they come out and you cannot, if I tell you this is so good that you can't tell the difference between a guy with his real hair and a guy with the Dermabond technique. We've tried on four different occasions to pick out the person with the Dermabond technique. Robin, could we do it?
No. Even now, Scott, you must meet people sometimes who don't know who you are.
Yes, occasionally.
Do they ever say to you, oh, you're wearing a rug?
Never. I've never heard that once.
No, because this isn't like a guy wearing a rug. This is the Dermabond technique. It's a whole different thing. Look, I'm just going to tell you this. It is so good. I'm telling you it's good. And I'm saying, don't take my word for it. Just call 1-800-835-HAIR. And make an appointment to see what we're talking about. 1-800-835-HAIR. Or at least get the brochure. You're going to be amazed. 1-800-835-HAIR.
92.3 K-Rock. We're back with a man who flies first class. While Jackie and Fred fly coach.
It's
Howard Stern.
What is he stuttering, John?
Dominic Barber's on the phone.
Oh, Dominic has a funny Baba Booey story.
Really?
Yeah,
was he there? He was. Oh.
No, Dominic.
Good morning,
this
everyone.
Is Dominic Barber, bloated attorney.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, dear.
Happy New Year.
Dominic, of course, is famous as Joey Buttafuoco's attorney. And Dominic the Big Shot, of course. Dominic calls me for like a month before the pay-per-view.
You want Joey for the pay-per-view? I could get him.
Yeah.
I could get Joey for the pay-per-view.
I go, yeah, sure, okay. You know, I didn't ask him for it, Joey. He just says
he offered.
He offered. Because he wants to be a big shot in my eyes. Dominic's always trying to impress me. Like
I don't
he's like
know
a
what goes on with Dominic.
And so like, you know, a couple of weeks go by, I don't hear from Dominic. I call him back. I go, hey, what happened to the Joey thing? So, okay, I said, fine. Yeah, I said, you offered Joey. I'm waiting for Joey. So then a couple more weeks go by, and we're getting closer to the date. And I said, what's going on with Joey? He
says, well, I don't know if we could get a satellite dish to the letter in prison. You might have to tape something in advance. I go, that's fine. I said, all we want Joey to do is do the countdown New Year's Eve, you know, 10-9-8-7-6-5-4. Oh, that'll be fine. That'll be fine. It's all arranged. It's in the bag.
It's in the bag. So the next thing I know, I don't hear from Dominic. Nobody hears from Dominic. Dominic's like,
you can't
like,
get Dominic on the phone.
Dominic, tell your wife to quiet down.
I was going
to
say, is that Dominic's dinner?
That's Dominic's dinner.
Come here, Fluffy. Come here, Fluffy. It's time for dinner. Roll over on this bread.
Roll over on this bread. So then like it's like a day before the event, I go, Dominic, when are we going to tape with Joey?
Do you have a good relationship with Fox?
I go, Dominic, what do you mean? What does Fox have to do with me taping? He goes,
It seems I made a deal with Fox. They have the exclusive of Joey in prison.
I go, well, why didn't you say that from the beginning? You made a deal with Fox for Current Affairs.
He doesn't know what kind of deals he makes.
No, he doesn't know what. He goes,
you better call Fox and ask him if it's okay.
I go, I'm not calling anybody. You're the one who offered Joey.
At least you found him. Nobody could find him.
Yeah, and then I couldn't find Dominic. He goes, let me check in. And then he ran off to Puerto Rico.
Yeah, without a call back?
Without a call back.
Oh, Dominic.
Dominic, what's the matter? Why do you always have to be such a big shot?
I made as many deals as I could.
You're insane.
My son Jason was down in Puerto Rico.
How can a 450-pound man hide so easily from me?
Just disappeared.
He just disappeared from me.
You know, I did see Siegfried and Roy make an elephant disappear. Yeah. So it is possible.
Yeah, I think Dominic's now representing Siegfried and Roy.
You know, I ate an entire birthday cake Friday night.
You know what's funny? So then I say to Dominic, I get back from my vacation. Then Dominic's calling me every 10 minutes when I get back from vacation because now pay-per-view's over.
Yeah.
And
right.
I can't bug him by Joey Buttafuoco.
Right, he can talk to you again.
Yeah, now I can talk to you. He goes, come on, let's go to Atlantic City. So I said, I don't want to go to Atlantic City. He goes, come on, let's play cards. Okay, I said, let's play cards. I said, let's have a card game. We'll have our usual card game, the usual guys, you know, Dan Foreman, you know, the guys.
Right.
So Dominic says,
great, I'll arrange the whole thing.
So anyway.
You're making my voice too thick. It's deeper, but not that thick.
Some days it sounds like you're underwater. Don't
yeah.
Underwater.
Dairy.
So I said, okay, we'll play cards. So Friday, I come down with, like, I don't know, my wife was sick and she gave me something. I was having the worst runs and everything.
Ooh.
So I called Dominic. I go, listen, Dominic, I'm not feeling good. I'm going to have to cancel the card. I can't go to the card game, but you guys play.
Yeah.
No, we're not playing unless you play. It's not fun unless you play.
So all the guys had to be called. The game had to be canceled because I didn't play.
Oh, Dominic.
What happened?
And then Dominic doesn't call Dan Foreman to tell him the game's canceled. Then I end up with Dan at my house. Because,
are you kidding?
Yeah.
I am.
What happened is, number one, you
all right, Dominic, so what happened in Puerto Rico? You were saying...
You had one of your psychomatic colds. All of a sudden, you thought you were sick.
Psychomatic?
Yeah, you thought you were sick.
Wait, wait. What did I have?
A psychomatic cold.
Dominic, what law school did you go to?
You thought you were sick. So Monday morning, Friday morning...
No, listen to me. Meanwhile, I said to Dominic, I have to go into the city today. I had to go into the city Friday. I said, listen, if I get back and I'm feeling better, we'll play. I'll come, but don't put this pressure on me. He goes, no, I'm canceling the game. Meanwhile, Friday night, I felt great. I would have come to the card game. I would have played.
It was canceled.
It was canceled because Dominic doesn't even want to be in a room with people unless I'm there.
Yeah.
You canceled the game. Not only that, there was a birthday cake. I had to eat the whole cake myself.
Dominic, tell us what happened in Puerto Rico.
Well, my son was down there with Gary, and my kids were there when Gary was there with his wife.
Yeah, but Dominic offered, you know, Dominic is a very generous guy. He always says, hey, if you want to use my villa in Puerto Rico, you can use it.
Right.
And, of course, we all turn him down because nobody wants to owe Dominic anything.
Right.
So, but Gary, of course.
Gary goes all the
time. Gary takes advantage of any of my friends.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll go, Dominic. I'm going to Puerto Rico.
No, Gary is supposed to say no, but he doesn't know. He'll never say no.
Why should he say no?
He offered it to me, boy.
Because it's just not appropriate.
Oh, stop it. All right. I'm not a sponsor. What are you talking about?
I'm a friend.
I'm not a sponsor. All right, so go ahead.
The son was down there with my daughters. I had already flown back. And my son said that you have to see Gary's wife in a bathing suit. She's incredible. She's
right.
A beautiful woman. But walking down the beach, there's someone next to her, about 2 feet shorter, with like a gorilla walk.
I thought you said that your son said it looked like Jane with Cheetah. He says it's like she's walking with her pet.
You have to see it. She's incredible looking.
She's a beautiful girl.
No, but she's just incredible.
Yeah.
And next to her is some guy like almost walking like doing the Baba Booey.
You know, yeah. One day we were walking, and I did see them all behind me because we only crossed over for like a day.
Yeah.
And I swore I could hear laughing. And now I know.
And she's outrageous, buddy.
I'm Jake. I'm hungry.
All right, very good.
Goodbye.
That's the great attorney, Dominic Barbara, off on probably an important case. What case are you on today?
Lunch.
Lunch.
Lunch. Case of lunch.
Thank you, Dominic.
Lunch.
Case of lunch. Dominic yakking it up on Baba Booey's expense. Like Dominic doesn't look funny next to his wife.
Yeah, really. Like, that's like not a thing. Yeah.
Dominic yakking it up. 450 pounds, you got about 6 months left. Yak it up all you want. And then Dominic had a whole big thing. Did you hear about Dominic's big heart attack or something?
No.
Well, he didn't have a heart attack. He calls up,
you didn't know I was in the hospital for 5 days.
Really?
Yeah, what happened? He goes,
well, I felt chest pains. It was really bad.
And they're doing all these tests on Dominic, and they're trying to
actually find his chest.
Yeah, so he's doing, and he's in there, and he knows he's, you know, they're pretty sure he's had cardiac arrest and the whole thing.
Not
so,
cardiac arrest.
What is it called?
A myocardial infarction.
Yeah, an infarction. So, anyway, and Dominic's laying in the hospital, and he's like,
I'm not going to eat anymore. I'm going to get myself in shape. If I survive this,
all right, so.
Making all kinds of promises.
Right. So 5 days later, they come in, they did all the tests, and what happened?
What?
Dominic had gas. All right, wait a second.
5 days of gas?
And the doctor, for some reason, says to Dominic, not only did you have gases, but we did a test on your cholesterol and the veins and everything, and it turns out you have the heart of a 30-year-old man.
Oh,
he says you have the... And so Dominic now is eating more than ever.
Oh,
that's
no.
That's all they had to...
I could eat like crazy.
So now he's testing his heart.
Oh, now he's up to 700 pounds. Now he's daring his heart to give up.
If I was a doctor, I would have put a good scare into him.
Yeah, why tell him that he's okay?
I don't know. But anyway, Dominic is a great guy. I hope he does lose weight, because I don't want to lose Dominic. And you know what?
I wish he would get into shape.
That's right. The legal world doesn't want to lose Dominic. He has set so many precedents.
A man who can argue somatic illnesses.
Right, somatic illness.
He got somatic illness. He got somatic illness.
For the record, it's psychosomatic, Your Honor. All right, anyway. Well, there you go. He really is a great attorney, though. If I was getting divorced, I definitely would hire him.
Be the first.
Yeah, he's a barracuda.
Be the first to hire him.
Oh, I have him on retainer.
Over the weekend, I went to dinner with Dominic Barbara, and you know how he's a fat guy, and fat guys never eat in front of you? Dominic's in a new phase. Now he eats in front of me. I think he finally gave up. He started eating in front of me.
What is that all about?
I don't know, man, but boy, he can eat. He goes like this. We're sitting there, right? We went to some joint called...
Bobby Vans.
Bobby Vans.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby Vans.
What is good? Bobby Vans?
Ooh, that's good.
Yeah?
That's a good place.
Out there in the Hamptons?
Yeah, good food. Yeah, Dominic takes me there.
Come on, I'm gonna call it Bobby Vans.
I've never heard of Bobby Vans.
Bobby Vans.
Did he drive you in his Rolls
Royce? Hell no, I wouldn't get in that. He's got
a
Bentley.
Do you know how much a Bentley costs?
No, how much?
$215,000.
Where is he getting this money?
He must buy these things used.
It's
no.
It's a brand new Bentley he's driving around. He goes, come here. Let my son JJ drive your car, and you'll drive with me. I go, no thanks. I don't want to be seen in that gaudy piece of crap.
I was just reading. They had a recall of these stupid Bentleys.
Uh-oh.
And they said it's a $215,000 car.
Because he goes, I love my car.
And I went, why? Give the money to charity.
Because it's so dear.
You got the, I mean, is it so great?
I mean, like it does what every other car does. It gets you from place to place.
Would you want to ride around in a $215,000 car knowing that someone could dent it or scratch? I'd be a nervous wreck.
No, I'd be with the car all the time.
Yeah, and
I mean,
everyone's staring at you.
Yeah, right. Well, he loves that. I never seen a guy who wants to be famous so
Why
bad.
Why does he want all of that attention?
Well, I'll tell you, he is getting famous, though, because when I walk around with him, people go, oh, my God, look who it is, Dominic Barber. They don't even,
really?
Yeah, they don't even notice me. He's a bigger star than anybody.
Now I'm really getting worried.
I go, who knows this big fatso? Because
that show isn't it supposed to be.
I guess he's a big star now. You should see. And he's like, so he sits down to eat, right?
Yes.
And he goes, and he's got a girlfriend now. You know, he's there with the girlfriend.
Girlfriend's hanging in there.
Oh yeah.
She can't. Is she pretty?
Pretty, yeah.
I can't believe it.
Pretty.
Is she blind?
He's got a $215,000 car.
Dominic, he's telling me he sent her on a pretty woman makeover.
He sent her on a makeover.
Pretty woman makeover. He goes, yeah, she's beautiful. He goes,
this is what I want. I want you to lose 10 pounds. I want to get you all new outfits, and I want a new hairdo.
She loved
it. Pretty woman makeover.
I don't know.
Get some weight on your vagina. Get some weight on your vagina.
So, anyway.
Look what I got you.
Yeah, but they're in love, man. You know, that's a whole thing going on there.
Now I don't believe in love.
Love is highly overrated.
Now, here's the question. Does he pay attention to you more than her? Or
yeah, always me more. Always me more.
I'm going to send you a makeover.
First of all, you know what?
Wait a minute.
He's so
order?
Embarrassing.
The
he's,
girlfriend, you, food. What's the order of
food?
Attention? Food?
Food is always first. Then me, then the girlfriend. But anyway, you got to hear. Because even the girlfriend goes, Dominic couldn't figure out what to wear tonight for you. You know, it's like, you know. He's in love with me. And I'll tell you, I'll give you an example.
And have you ever noticed his outfit after he goes
No. He's so fat. And when he eats, his belly is flopping over the table.
Ugh.
And he takes a napkin and puts it over his belly, like a bib.
It doesn't go on his lap.
And that napkin is so dirty after a meal.
Really?
Because he's so fat, his arms are tiny.
He can't reach over his belly?
They could go,
crab cakes for the whole table.
So the crab cakes will go in the middle, and he has to reach over and spear a crab cake with his fork.
He can't reach it.
Yeah, he can't reach it.
It's like fishing for him.
Yeah, he's like,
here's a crab cake for everybody.
I'll give you an example of how much he's in love with me. And it's horrible. I can't go out with this guy.
Well, it's
dessert comes, right?
Yeah.
So they ordered a banana split for the whole table.
Uh-oh.
So the Dominic goes,
put it in front of Howard.
Put it, like, just 12 people at the table. Put it in front of Holland.
It's got to be your
It's like, stop looking at me. Stop concentrating on me. Stop telling the waiter what to do for me.
Let you fade into the background.
Pay attention to your girlfriend.
But tell the story about the steak. I thought that was
okay, funny. All right. So we get to this place, Bobby Vans. And Dominic's one of those guys who's real loud at the table, orders waiters around, and is actually just nasty to the waiters.
Yeah.
But they don't know. We had
Does
to go.
Does he have a usual table? Does he have
a whole thing? Yeah.
This is how, whenever you need a reservation, you tell.
Oh, so he sits down. First, we'll order some drinks.
I have a special drink. I have.
He says to the waiter,
I have vodka with cranberry, but a little bit of cranberry, and two lemons.
The two lemons are very important.
And the two lemons. Howard, you must have it.
All right, Dominic. I don't want that, though. I really don't want. I don't want to drink.
No. Okay. One for me. Who else wants the special Dominic drink?
You know, like the special Dominic drink. Who else wants?
He's creating.
And he's yelling. And I'm surprised he doesn't have a heart attack right at the table.
Who wants special Dominic drink?
Some five people want it.
Okay. Make the special. Now, go make it again.
So he talks real loud, like
he's
the waiter knows on his
recipe.
Vodka, little bit of cranberry. Two double lemons, and tell him it's for Dominic. For Dominic.
Like the goddamn bartender cares.
Right.
You know? Then the drink comes. It's horrible. It is so horrible.
Really?
A monster wouldn't drink. Frankenstein would run out of the room.
But
is
it the way Dominic likes it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, Dominic. Ah. He sips it. Ah. Like Alexa Hente.
Very good.
Then it comes time to order.
Isn't this great?
Comes time to order food. So the girlfriend says to Leslie, lovely girl, says to Dominic, honey, let's get the steak for two.
No. He says
to the waiter. He goes,
look, I want the steak for two for one. For me, for Dominic, for Dominic. Steak for two for one.
I love that.
He goes,
first my barley soup.
My barley soup.
My barley soup.
It's as loud as can be, so everyone will hear his order.
The whole restaurant knows his order.
My barley soup. Then I want the Harry salad.
Harry salad.
And Howard. And
God forbid.
Oh, he's ordering for you?
No, he goes,
and Howard, I put extra vinegar on it.
This salad does not need extra vinegar.
Barley soup, Harry salad. And then steak for two, for one. For one, for me, Dominic.
Then, you know. And then he goes, and then he starts waving his arms around.
For the table. Meanwhile, this is what he, cream spinach, potatoes, crab cake.
Like we need that. There's not enough food. But I know he's nervous and insecure.
Right.
Then dessert comes. It was Scott Einziger's girlfriend's birthday, Maya's birthday.
Right.
So, Beth, my girlfriend, had ordered a special little dessert platter with our name on it and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, how sweet.
Very nice, right? The platter comes out, and the platter's just for a presentation. It has her name on it, and then they bring out some desserts for the table. Well, Dominic sees the little platter at first. He sees his 12 people. He goes,
well, we need more desserts. More desserts.
He can't just let it happen.
So they bring out a banana split.
Bring another banana split. Put it in front of Howard. He likes it.
Shut up. He's insane.
How do you enjoy yourself when all of this is going on?
I get very drunk and I laugh. I just laugh. Dominic.
First of all,
steak for two for one. Me, Dominic.
Bring up a cow.
Where's my Bentley?
Robin?
Do you know we went up to the waiter afterwards and apologized for your behavior?
First of all, you called Bobby Vance to speak to Joe. I've been going there 15 years. They all love me.
And they can't wait to go out of
business. You want to know the truth? You want to take the truth?
Yeah.
All right. And afterwards, we went to the waiter, and even the waiter said, gee, you know, I feel bad. You know, some of the people were kind of rough at the table. And then we said, no, just one person, right? He goes, yeah, we thought you were great. The waiter was so nice. Such a nice man.
How many times did
Then his steak comes up. Wait. I didn't tell you the best part.
The kind of guy who wants the waiter really to work for that tip.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Wait. Then Dominic. But he does tip big.
I'm telling you, he tips big, but the guy really works for it.
Wait. I didn't finish the story. So then.
How many times did we go to a restaurant?
Twice.
And then you go back the next night.
I felt bad for you.
You went again?
Loved it.
Same restaurant.
Yeah.
With Dominic.
Yes, of course.
Then don't complain to me.
He knew Bobby I was down. Going. I couldn't say no.
Don't complain to me.
Oh, wait. Then he goes. Then he goes like this.
The steak finally comes.
Oh, this isn't right. This isn't what I ordered. We like it sliced. We like it sliced. We like the steak sliced.
Who's we? You get two for one.
You get, well, it's two people inside of Dominic. He goes, and then he pushes the plate aside and he makes a face like a baby. Oh. Like, oh. He sends food back. I know. Thank God.
Oh, I'm sure they threw it on the floor.
I hope they threw it on the floor and defecated on it.
They brought it back.
Yeah, right. I hope there was fecal matter.
Oh, hey, you made it much better this time. Little Bobby Vance.
Get the shoe print in there.
Howard. If you had such a bad time, why did you make me go back the next night?
I'm really shocked, Dominic.
I'm a glutton for punishment. Besides, I needed something to talk about.
And secondly, if I when I take care of you, I heard you say to Beth, oh, he gave me half his salad. Did you say that?
Don't give me anything. Leave me alone. Oh, and then here's a better part of this. So then we get out of the restaurant, and My friend says to me, Howard, I'm coming over. Where do you live? Dominic goes, oh, he lives at what?
He
screams out my business. He's just
maps.
He's whacked out of his skull.
Maps to the stars.
But he's Dominic.
Thank God you have a radio
then
show.
He calls me yesterday.
I'm on TV. Quick, turn it on. Turn it.
I say, leave me alone. I had enough of Dominic.
Well, happy summer.
Happy summer. You're going away for the summer, right?
Well, Power of Attorney, my show on Fox, it's Dominic Barbara week, so all the shows are me this week.
Is that right?
Me.
So I want you to make sure you watch.
I got to admit, man, the guy walks down the street, people are like,
know him,
there's Dominic Barbara.
Yeah.
No,
he probably pays those people.
Said? You didn't hear what the guy said in front of the restaurant? There's Dominic Barbara. Who's that tall guy with the long hair next to him?
He's not kidding. It's true. They all know him. They all love Dominic.
Dominic paid those people.
He pays people. Right? Pretty Woman Makeover. Didn't you do that?
What's the Pretty Woman Makeover?
He's out of his mind. All I know is he calls me up. We go out to dinner the first night.
Where do you get the Pretty Woman Makeover?
Robin wants a Pretty Woman Makeover.
Robin, the second night, I have plans. My kids are out. Jason's out. He says to me, we have to go out again. I said, oh. No.
See, you're calling him.
Get rid of this guy.
I am. I'm calling you.
You're calling him. Yeah. And then you want to come in here,
Dominic,
and
I'm never calling you again. Don't worry.
I love you and I miss you.
Bye-bye. Miss me. I miss you.
I haven't been away from him for a day.
Dominic does the fat guy thing, too.
I look fat?
By the way, you've gained back all your weight.
Oh,
whatever weight
you
lose.
How did you have steak for two for one and not gain back?
Steak for two for one. Power of menu.
Your friend said I look gorgeous. You were jealous, weren't you?
You're a very handsome man. The discussion afterward is that Dominic's a very handsome man. Too bad he's so fat. All right, goodbye.
Goodbye.
It's Dominic Barbara week.
On Power of Attorney.
All me.
I'm going to call you later, Robin. Bye.
Good.
I'm going to call you later. I'll give you a Pretty Woman Makeover.
And so you had dinner with him twice, you little devil.
Yep.
You lied. You enjoyed yourself watching him.
Carol. I did. You got it. You know what? I'm going to invite you to dinner with Dominic.
Oh,
you'll have the best time. I'm just afraid they're going to do something to the food because he's so obnoxious.
Yeah, and then they do it to the whole table.
Oh,
yeah.
And then you got to pretend like you're a nice guy, too, overly nice.
Oh, you got to be very nice.
Apologize for him.
To make up for him.
Yeah. Yeah, that's weird stuff.
And then you got to go slip the waiter some more money, even. Dominic picked up the tab, right?
No, the first night, second night I did. Oh. Joe, you're on the air.
Yeah, how you doing, Howard? I saw Dominic on Mother's Day at the Garden City Hotel there, this big grand buffet, you know?
Yeah.
He looked like an offensive lineman going for the line.
Out of my weight, steak for two for one. I want salad for 15. How is salad?
For me,
Dominic. Excellent vinegar.
I think he was there with his girlfriend's son, who looked like he was 15 years old.
Right.
He, like, trampled him to get to the,
poor kid.
Dominic fell over him.
But I got to say, I was walking out by the desserts, and the waiters, he must have really over-tipped them because they came up, and they were talking among themselves to the maitre d', saying, look, this is from Dominic. So, I mean, he does take care of these.
No, he's a very generous guy. He is. He always picks up the tab. He's a nice guy. That's why
I went
out.
Howard, I've been listening to you since you were on AM.
Wow. You go back a long way. That's like 9 million years ago. All right. Take care, Joe.
Good work.
Later. That's funny. That is a Gay Ramon, you're on the air.
Hey, baby, how you doing?
Hey, what's happening?
Hey, listen, I got a little story. The day of the cabbie fight, I pulled up right behind Dominic and his Bentley. We pulled in the garage there, and two drops of water hit his car. And he went off on the parking attendant like he was a little boy. He just kept yelling at him, yelling at him. He was with that gay son of his.
His son's not gay.
He is so gay.
No, he's not. He's got a girlfriend. I saw him there. I saw the kid over the weekend. He's a good kid. Hey, so I said to Dominic, I said, what's it like to have Dominic as a father? It's not easy.
I can imagine.
Yeah. But, you know, that's why. Why would you want a $215,000 car? A drop of water gets on it, you get freaked out.
Crazy.
It's a beautiful car.
It is beautiful, but it
won't. Two drops of water hits it, and he freaks out.
Dominic Barber.
How do you drive that in traffic?
Was he yelling?
He was yelling at the top of his lungs. What are you doing? Get my car over there.
Dominic Barber's
water's
stomach.
Hitting it.
Dominic Barber's stomach is on the phone. What is it, Dominic?
My stomach. I'm Dominic's stomach, and I'm full of yarn and spit.
I beat her at basketball, and I'm hoping for the same success today. Although I'm a little concerned, it's a fix. I'm not sure. Well, I'm just wondering if she knew any of the questions or might have been given some of the suggestions before.
In advance.
Yeah, I'm a little worried about that. Not totally. I believe in the integrity of the show. Who's playing me here? You lose me and I'll pay you $1,000. Come on. Gotta beat her.
I don't think so.
Slip me the answer. You good at this?
I'm pretty good. I'm not worried.
Okay, we're going to play Jeopardy now. Let me lay it out to you how this all came about.
All right,
Robin was on.
Oh, I am going to complain. These are not official Jeopardy buzzers.
Who cares?
Like Family Feud buzzer.
Yes. Okay. Here's how it came about. Robin was on Jeopardy. A bunch of loudmouths kept saying Robin wasn't any good on Jeopardy. Meanwhile, she won. First loudmouth.
Let me just say this. I won real Jeopardy.
First loudmouth is Neil. Neil, you're a listener of ours. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And you say you're great at Jeopardy.
Yeah. You know, I sit around my house. I play Jeopardy sometimes.
How old are you?
I'm 20 years old.
20 years old?
Yes, sir.
And you say you can beat Robin. We're going to find out today.
Yeah, I'm pretty positive.
And what did you say? If you don't beat Robin, what happens?
I believe the bet was $200.
$200?
I thought it was five,
but we'll hold you to two. Dominic sits to your left. Dominic Barber, the bloated attorney, who is on Viagra. You saw Robin, and you said you could beat her.
I hope I can.
Yeah, you hope you can, because you're going to be weighed.
Oh, man.
And I believe you're over 300 pounds. I don't care what you say.
We're not betting money on that, right?
Yes, we are. And Robin Quivers, you are here, obviously, to shut these two guys up.
I'm just playing. I don't have a grudge against anybody. I did my job when I went on Jeopardy, and that's what I was supposed to do.
Also, working the board is Patrice from Scores, a very beautiful stripper. Isn't that right, Patrice?
Hey, how are you?
How are you, baby?
I'm wonderful.
I've partied with Patrice on many occasions. I know Patrice very, very well.
All right.
And she's a very fun girl. You were telling me you've already taken Viagra?
I have.
Now, how did this happen? Why would a girl like you need Viagra?
It wasn't anything more than I thought that I needed. Just something a little extra.
Something to enhance your love life?
And same I thought it me. Might. I
what
thought
happened?
It might.
Were you with a man? You were not at Scores at the time when you took Viagra, were you?
No.
No. So you were with a man in your private life?
Yes.
Okay. Were you with a woman or a man?
Both.
Both. You were with a woman and a man.
Yes.
When was this?
Last week.
Last week?
Yes.
Where was this? At your place?
At my apartment.
No kidding. A woman and a man.
Yes.
And you were on Viagra?
Hold on a second, please.
Viagra, not Viagra.
And a woman. And the woman was another stripper?
Yes, it was.
So she was very sexy?
Very sexy.
Okay. And the guy, was he some lucky customer or was he just some guy you knew?
Somebody I know.
Uh-huh. Boyfriend?
Now, did everybody take Viagra or did just...
Two out of three parties.
I see.
The two girls or the boy and the girl?
The boy and the girl.
Okay, that was you.
Yes.
What happens to a woman when she takes Viagra? Share with us.
From what I realized was being as... normally horny as I am.
You are a horny girl.
I don't know any other way to put it.
She's a horny girl.
Horny girl. It kind of enhanced it a little bit. Not much as I thought it would have, mm-hmm. or much as I liked it would have, but it did work.
And where did you feel it?
In the vagina.
In the genital area.
Really?
I mean, was it more outside than in? Or
it was more outside than in.
Really?
Definitely more outside. Robin understands.
Yes.
It was more outside
scary
than
thing
in.
Is, finally, scary yes. thing is, I understand. Yes. Do you want to climb on Dominic that you're both on Viagra? Do you both have
considering I've seen Dominic before, and he's never noticed me before, considering he's always, like, handing out, you know, hanging out.
No offense, before, Dominic had no Viagra. I mean, now he's on it. He's ready for anybody.
He's only by the buffet. I don't know what the deal is. is.
I know, isn't that weird? But anyway, Patrice, thank you from Scores, who's going to be working our board right now, and let's play Jeopardy. Now it's time to put up or shut up. Let me, for the audience at home, tell you the categories. First category, body and health. Second category, buildings and places. Our third category, matrimony. Our fourth category, toys and games. And finally, trade names. Okay? There'll be one round on this board, and then we'll have Final Jeopardy.
All right.
Now, we haven't decided who will go first. Robin?
Let the listener go.
All right, let the listener go first.
Hell with him. I want to go first.
No, no. Shut up, Dominic.
Stop whining.
Remember, these two guys said they could beat Robin after her appearance, and I say there's no chance in hell. Robin's too good. Neil, go ahead.
We shall see.
All right.
I'll take toys and games for 100.
This Mattel doll has her own Ferrari. Neil is first.
Barbie.
Wrong.
Wrong.
I got it. What is Barbie?
That's right. Robin's right, and she had the light on. Gary, make sure you call out who the person is. Okay, here we go. Robin gets 100, and Neil loses 100. Yeah. Dominic, if your light isn't on, you can't give out the answer.
I have a one.
And Neil, please remember to say who is, okay? You would have been right on that.
What is? It's a question.
Robin Quivers, go ahead.
I will take body and health for 100.
The brain is made up of these three parts, the stem, the cerebrum, and this.
Robin.
The cerebellum.
Wrong. Oh.
What is the...
Dominic.
What is the cortex?
Wrong.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
Stay out of this.
The answer is, what is the cerebellum?
Oh, did we none of us ask that?
You didn't say cerebellum. All right, so Robin, you lose 100, and Dominic, you lose 100.
So I'm even.
How'd I lose 100?
Yes.
You just answered the question.
You answered it wrong. All you had to do is say what Robin did is put what is. All right, Robin, you still control the board.
Okay, body and health for 200.
Body and health for 200. Whoa. I can't say this worst word. Climacteric. Climacteric is another term for when a woman no longer ovulates.
Robin.
That would be menopause. What is menopause?
Right.
Ooh.
You got enough? That's fine. That's fine. For 200, Robin is right. Robin, go ahead.
Okay, body and health for 300.
This disease in blacks results when there is a flaw
Dominic.
In the hemoglobin molecule.
Dominic was in first.
Robin.
What is sickle cell anemia?
That is correct. That's plus 300 for Robin, minus 300 for Domino.
Wow,
Robin, go ahead.
Okay, body and health for 400.
By the way, boys, not so easy, is it?
No.
You know, Howard, Neil was bragging to me that he got a 1310 on his SATs.
Yeah, big deal.
Big deal.
In 1882, German physician Robert Koch, K-O-C-H, discovered the bacterium that causes lung disease.
What's the question? How could be a question?
There's no question.
In 1882, German physician Robert Koch, K-O-C-H, discovered the bacterium that causes lung disease. You have to obviously name the...
name what?
Disease.
The disease.
Robin?
What is tuberculosis?
That is correct.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Neither did anyone else. Go ahead, Robin.
No.
Okay. Body and health for 500.
This blood type is considered to be the universal donor.
Robin.
What is O?
That is correct. And now our score is Robin 1300, Dominic minus 400, Neil minus 100. You guys want to continue? Robin, go ahead.
No.
Keep going, guys.
Go ahead, Robin.
Okay.
This is terrible.
Can't wait to see what Dominic weighs.
Oh, man.
Trade names for 100.
Trade names for 100. As of 1992, it is the only American manufacturer of motorcycles.
Robin.
What is Harley Davidson?
Robin, go ahead.
What trade names for 200?
Inch for inch, foot for foot. It's the nation's fastest growing sandwich chain. Neil.
What is Subway?
That is correct. For 200. Neil finally on the board at plus 100.
I know.
Where
food.
Am I?
I'll go for toys and games for 200.
Named for its resemblance to the fourth letter in the Greek alphabet, a delta kite is shaped like this. And the answer is, what is triangle?
That's a game?
What is triangle?
A kite is a toy.
And games.
Dominic doesn't even know.
He didn't know what's going on.
Let me get to a courtroom.
What's going on here?
Get him a donut.
And let's continue with Robin Quivers.
That wasn't me.
It's sorry, Neil.
All right. Toys and games for 300.
The chess notation, QB, stands for this. QB? The answer is, what is Queen's Bishop? Neil, continue.
Toys and games for 400.
This game made Uncle Pennybag so famous you can buy a watch with his face on it.
Robin.
What is Monopoly?
Correct. Robin, go ahead.
Let's see. Buildings and Places for 100.
I'm so embarrassed.
This Houston structure is climate controlled to a constant 72 degrees.
Dominic.
Dominic.
What is the Astrodome?
That is correct for 100. You are now at minus 300. Dominic. Robin is at 1,800 and Neil at 100.
Matrimony for 100.
Yeah. Lisa Hartman is married to this country music superstar.
Robin.
Who is Clint Black.
That is correct. Go ahead, Robin.
Let's see. Buildings and Places for 200.
Buildings and Places for 200. Opened in 1931. It was the world's tallest building until 1971.
Dominic.
What is the Empire State Building?
That is correct for 200. Dominic's at minus 100. Stay with
No. You don't have to laugh, Robin. That's not nice.
Robin's at 1,900. Neil's at 100. Go ahead. These are the two loud mouths. Go ahead.
Yeah.
What is buildings for 300 for buildings?
The fourth version of this building opened in 1968 on the site of Penn Station.
Oh, Jesus.
The answer is, what is Madison Square Garden?
Oh.
Dominic, go ahead.
Buildings for 400.
We're doing very well in this category.
With seats for only 33,925 people, this Red Sox structure is the smallest in baseball. Neil.
What is Fenway Park?
That is correct for $400. And Neil is at plus 300. Robin at 1,900. Dominic at minus 100.
Go on, Neil.
Buildings and places for 500.
In the NFL, the Hoosier Dome is the home to this team.
Neil.
What is Indianapolis Colts?
That is correct for 500. And that puts Neil at a whopping 800. Robin at 1,900. Dominic at minus 100.
All right.
Wait, 900.
At 800.
He's 900.
He had
500.
He had 500. He just answered a $500 question.
So it's
1,000. I don't know about that.
I have 500.
Guys, are you correct back there?
Hank,
we'll double check that. Go ahead, Neil.
Toys and games
That's
for
correct.
500.
Toys and games for 500.
I have no chance in this.
You use this to strike the ball in croquet.
Robin.
What is a mallet?
That is correct for 500.
Trade names for 300.
Okay, trade names for 300. This beverage company owns Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. Neil.
What is Coke?
Wrong. Dominic. No.
What is Pepsi? Robin. No. It's Robin. It's Robin.
Robin. Robin.
What is Pepsi?
Good.
Oh, I said it.
I had it.
Believe me.
Cheated me.
Gary, pull out the next. He can't see.
You got to do it fast. You got to do it fast.
Gary, at least point with your teeth.
Go ahead, Robin.
You big fat
trade names for 400. Johnson & Johnson uses this trade name for this adhesive bandage. Neil.
What is Band-Aid? What are Band-Aids?
That's right.
All
right. Okay,
tell
good.
Tell him if he's right. We don't
Sorry,
know.
Spaced out. Go ahead.
Don't worry about it.
Neil, go ahead.
Trade names for 500.
Here we go. Since its invention, table tennis has also been called by this trade name.
Neil.
What is ping pong?
That is correct.
What am I doing here?
You're going to get weighed.
Neil is at 1,600. Robin's at 2,700. Dominic's at minus 100.
Oh,
and Neil has control of the board.
I'll go with matrimony for 200.
This Philippine couple moved to Hawaii in 1986.
Dominic.
Imelda Marcos. Who is Imelda Marcos?
And?
Wrong.
Who are the Marcoses?
Robin.
Robin.
It's who is Ferdinand and Imelda Marcos?
Correct.
Oh.
Ferdinand and Imelda Marcos. Robin, you have control of the board.
300 in matrimony.
Marilyn Monroe married this man two times, once in a civil ceremony and the second in a Jewish ceremony.
Robin.
Who is Joe DiMaggio?
No. Wrong.
Oh, what am I thinking of?
Dominic.
Miller.
Right. Who is Arthur Miller? That is correct.
Yeah.
For 300. Dominic, you have brought yourself to zero. Robin at 2,600. Neil at 1,600.
Okay.
Robin, go ahead.
I got it.
Oh, sorry, Dominic, go ahead.
Oh, that's right. Cheating. There's no way to go but there,
it's
Dominic.
A difference.
Matrimony, 500. How do you like
okay.
that?
Okay.
All right. They were the first married couple of all the Beatles.
Robin.
Who was John Lennon and Cynthia Lennon?
That is correct. Very good. Nice
okay,
nice one.
Okay, 400.
Although never married, this loving couple appeared in many movies together, including Pat and Mike.
Robin.
Spencer Tracy and Katharine Hepburn.
That is correct
Who are
again.
Spencer Tracy and Katharine Hepburn.
That is correct.
Can I play the...
Do you have
well,
any money?
Dominic, can't you can't even play you? At the end. Dominic has zero. Neil has 1,600 and Robin has 3,500.
Yeah.
From the way I'm looking at it, even if Neil doubles his score...
I can't win.
You can't win.
Yeah. Let's
Neil,
do it anyway.
That's beautiful.
Neil, now what do you say? You said you could beat Robin on the phone.
Let's just see if Robin bets some money in Final Jeopardy and I'll bet it all. What the hell?
Robin, let me ask you about it. Are you going to bet any money in Final Jeopardy?
If he doubles his score, he can't beat me.
No.
No.
Then why would I bet?
Exactly.
Howard, you should have heard him bragging in the green room.
What'd he say?
I couldn't get him to say he absolutely was going to win, but he says, I'm going to do very well. He was very close to saying it's a shoe.
Oh, I did 16 times better than the lawyer.
He did better than Dominic.
Neil, let's see how you do.
I have to be honest with you.
Neil, just out of curiosity, let's see how you do on Final Jeopardy.
Sure.
You don't even have to bet this one. You can do it all you want.
Everybody can do it, since it doesn't matter.
Here's the question. Live free or die is the motto of this northeastern state.
Ooh.
Don't look at each other's answers. Cover them up.
Dominic's cheating.
Of course. He's looking. Don't look at the answer, Dominic.
I wrote already.
Okay. The answer is not Trenton.
No!
What is that, Patrice, our stripper from Scores? What?
I think it should be topless for at least Double Jeopardy.
Yeah, please take off your top.
That's what I thought.
That's a great idea. Oh, you know, you really know how to make this game great. Beautiful. I don't need Viagra for those. Patrice is now topless.
Double Jeopardy.
All right, Neil. First of all, wait. Let's go to Dominic.
Dominic's changing his...
Oh, he saw mine.
Dominic. What was your first answer? I want to know.
What is New Hampshire?
No, what was your first answer?
Massachusetts.
All right, so you had it wrong. What did you have, Neil?
I had, what is New Hampshire?
That is correct. And Robin?
What is New Hampshire?
Yeah, you see, you wouldn't have beaten her anymore.
Yeah.
I rest my case.
You know what the motto of New Hampshire is? They have it on every license plate.
It is.
Live fat and die.
Oh! That's the motto of Dominic's house.
Right. So, Robin, when we come back,
we're going to win.
Can we all agree that I'm a better lawyer
and
than
Neil,
I am this?
Where's my $200?
I got to go get it.
All right. Neil will pay you $200, and Dominic, you will be weighed when we get back. And thank you, Patrice.
You're welcome, Howard.
Everyone go to Scores and meet Patrice.
You lost big.
Yeah, well, not too big. You know, I bet it all on Final Jeopardy, so I would have had $3,200, but she knew the answer anyway, so it wouldn't have made a difference at all. I'll bow to her. She did a hell of a job. She beat my ass.
But you were bragging out here before.
I thought I did pretty well with the categories that they gave me. They gave me some awful categories.
Well, I mean, that's what Jeopardy's all about.
Very true, very true. It's all about the luck of the draw, so I'll say that Robin got the luck of the draw this time.
All right, so where's your money?
She has it.
You already gave her the money?
Go ask her. Yeah, Dominic actually paid it for me.
Where's the money? Where's the cash?
Oh, I put it in there. I'm going to get some coffee.
There's the proud winner.
What happened, boys? What happened?
All right, Neil. Sorry you didn't make it.
That's all right, Candy.
Now the moment we've all been waiting for.
Woohoo!
Dominic Barber, the bloated attorney, is with us. He just lost in Jeopardy to Robin.
It was close.
He lost to everyone.
It was so great. Robin was in here gloating, and that guy Neil, the listener, he was like, I don't understand what happened. I lost. And Dominic's like, I can't believe it. I sit at home. I can answer the questions. And Robin goes, you don't understand. It's a lot harder once you play the real game.
No. It's harder playing a game, period.
Period.
I don't mind losing to the...
I can't wait to see how much you weigh.
I don't mind losing to Robin. I most object that I can't have my liberties with it today.
All right, listen. He's so unfunny.
Oh, man.
Here it is. Dominic, fat attorney. We've never been able to weigh him. This is his bet. I say, just to make this interesting, he's going to get on the scale
right now.
Yeah. Dominic suggested we each put $100 in the pot.
Okay.
We write down our name and his weight. And whoever is closest without going over.
That's it.
Wins the money.
Now, like the Price is Right.
Yeah. Yes. Now, if all of us go over, Dominic gets all the money.
Right.
Okay?
That's fair.
That's fair.
$100 each?
$100 each.
Robin, you put $200 up and I'll give you 2-1 odds.
Ooh.
And you can't get it.
You want the $200 you just gave me.
That's right.
That's right. I want you to win it back.
I'm only putting up $100.
Okay, who's playing?
We all are.
We all are?
Got to write your name down.
Is Fred playing? He left the room. There's something wrong with him. All right, so we're each putting $100. Who else wants to get in on this?
Gary?
I'm in. Dominic, stand up, because I've never really gotten a good look at it.
No.
Yeah.
Let's
try this up.
Come on, stand up.
Let me see. Turn around. Let me see a big fat ass. God, you are fat. Scott, the engineer, weighed 267, and he was half the size of Dominic.
Well, first of all, I have to actually be fair. Don't I also have to match everyone's bet? Because why should I win it if you're all wrong? I'll pay everyone also.
No, you're going through the humility.
Oh, all right. Yeah. Thanks.
Whoever's closest wins.
Oh, let me see you, Dominic.
God.
Stand
look,
up.
No, look who's here.
Tom wants to be in it.
Hey, Dominic, stand up.
I'll tell you what, Tom. Give us new phones and I'll be satisfied.
Tom, you going to play?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Sure. I, you know, I like a good bet.
I'm writing my... You got to write your name down.
Hold on. I'm
writing my
name down.
Should he stand up so we can see?
We saw already. How many times are you going to see?
I haven't seen.
Tough luck.
Now, you got to just... Come on. We got to get going on this. Jackie, 100. Fred, 100.
Can I ask one question?
Yeah.
How tall is Dominic?
How tall, Dominic?
5'9".
He'll lie about his height.
He lies about everything.
How tall are you, Dominic?
5'11".
Okay. He's 5'11".
Oh, wait, that changes things.
I think...
He lies so easily.
I know.
Yes.
Why does he not seem 5'11"?
Oh, leave me alone. I got zero in Jeopardy. I'm so embarrassed.
Is he how tall?
So do we have to get his weight exactly?
Yeah. No. It's the person who is
closest?
Under it. Closest and under.
Under it. Okay.
Howard, can I have your bet, please?
Okay. Here's mine.
Great.
And can you...
Did you collect the money?
No.
We're all good for it.
No.
How much is the bet?
$100.
Oh,
you got $100, John?
Can I play for 20?
No.
Oh, God.
Get out of here.
You shouldn't let him in here.
John, get out of here. Get out.
Let me play for 20.
No, get out.
Come on.
No.
Get out.
I knew
what, you were stiff. Do you have my 100, John?
Yes, I have your
100. You can play with my 100.
All right, I'll play with Robin's 100.
Oh, jeez. We almost had him out of here.
Now, let's not read the weights.
You just asked for me a minute ago.
Gary.
Let's not read the weights till I do it.
All right.
All right. Here's my 100.
His friend me.
Now, you know, you could bet, you could guess his weight at zero.
Right.
And
No,
I'm not doing that.
Get John's money back.
No, you can't do that.
No, you have Jackie. To be closest without going over.
I mean, it's got to start at 300, right?
No, it's
not necessarily. No,
who said
not necessarily. What are you getting? What are you making eyes at me for?
Everybody's already done it.
You're such a fat bastard.
He's Howard. You know what he's been trying to do all show that you haven't noticed?
What?
He's trying to help you cheat to win. Right. He's been trying to whisper the score to you.
He doesn't even know what he weighs. He's a dope. I don't even pay attention to him. All right, come on, get over there. We're gonna weigh him right now.
Howard wins, it's disqualified.
Howard, don't.
What? I haven't heard a thing. Then give me my money back now.
No, it's fair.
You're disqualified, man.
He's lost a lot of weight.
Yes. Everyone's in.
Yeah.
We're gonna write what.
Get on the scale.
Okay, just so you know, I set the scale at 330, so now I'm gonna bring it back. He's not 320. He's not 310. He's under 300.
Go ahead. Shh.
Okay.
Stop.
I went under 300.
Now he gets belligerent.
Which?
Wow, Dominic's way thinner than I thought he was.
Wow. Looks like I lost.
Guys,
okay, hold on.
Keep going.
You guys psych me out again. You don't know anything about
weight. Okay, hold on.
He's under 290.
He's way under 290. Dominic weighs 281 pounds.
I got 280!
Who had 280?
Me!
Did you really?
Hold on.
Wait. Robin, what did you have?
I had 315.
I had 295.
That's what I put, too.
I had 290 and I was going to make it.
Too
so
bad,
you had
Jackie.
280?
Give me your money.
I was going to go 295. That's what I went.
Oh, well.
What did you have, Fred?
I had 340.
Robin, I'll split the profit.
340?
You have to.
I had 304.
Since you guys were disqualifying me, I should win.
Right.
Well, here's my 100.
You weigh 281 and you're happy?
I was 271 at home this morning.
Jackie, have you money?
Yeah, I got to get you.
Without clothes, I was 271 this morning.
Boo.
Let's see that.
Booyah.
6 foot.
See, I didn't think he was over 300, but all you guys started carrying on.
I psyched you out. I bet 295.
Right.
Wait a second.
See?
When Scott was at his fattest, didn't,
he was 260.
Yeah, didn't you think that Dominic looked fatter than that?
Yes. Yeah.
But he's not as tall.
But he's so much bigger. He's girth.
And he's so fat.
No, but it's all, you know, muscle weighs more than fat. And Dominic
I don't think
has
this guy,
very little muscle.
I don't think this guy has an ounce of muscle.
No. He's
Scott
all
was fat.
Fat.
Dominic is round. 5'11", 280, still ain't thin.
He's not 5'11".
Right. I'm getting there. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah, well, it's better than I thought. I thought you weighed over 300.
He's like Humpty Dumpty.
I was 271 this morning.
He looks like Humpty Dumpty.
Yeah, he does.
Tweedly D.
Look, because you lost $100.
All right, Dominic Barber, thank you for coming in today and playing. He has a great practice out on Long Island. If you're in trouble, if you want to divorce your husband, you want to divorce your wife, get Dominic Barbara.
And my criminal practice and my negligence all has been very
successful. He's helped me many occasions.
12 lawyers. I've helped everyone in this room almost. The only one is Robin's, the only one I didn't. Yeah. And Fred in the future.
Right. Fred will need you at some point.
I'll bet that I won't.
Thank you, Dominic. Stuttering John, you win. How many hundreds of dollars did you win?
Let's see. How many people played? Gary, did you play?
3, 4, 5, 6, 700?
700.
Bastard.
And I'm going to split with Robin.
Really?
Well, he's playing with my 100.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you financed him. I wanted him out of here. See, we would have won.
Can't do that. You gotta
Dominic would have won, so it's just as well John got it.
Yeah.
Robin, you won and won big.
Yeah.
Not even a competition with this crew.
Well, you know, you keep trying to explain to people that the Jeopardy you see on TV is not as easy as sitting in your living room and knowing all the answers. There's absolutely no pressure there, and you don't have to hit a buzzer, and you're not competing with anybody. So, you know, when you put those factors into it, you know, not everybody performs well under pressure.
Unlike you, who's through.
Look, I am in a pressure cooker every day. What can I say? I handle it.
So, Dominic, you lost, and you lost big. You got killed by Robin.
It wasn't even close.
I know, it wasn't close at all.
I have to tell you, it's a lot tougher game. But I enjoyed it.
It's really tough, right?
Being a gentleman as I am, you know, I let Robin win.
Oh, you saying you let Robin win?
That's right.
Oh, Dominic. And you got on the scale, and you were actually a lot lighter than everybody thought. What
happened? That's right.
Got to do news. What's the difficulty?
Our game is on. Let's agree.
All right, I'll do it.
Let's agree.
What time?
Can I start calling the people to make sure?
Yeah, but I don't want like 20,000 guys. I hate playing cards with Dominic because here's Dominic's problem. He's got too much goddamn money, and any stakes that we play for, he wants to always raise the stakes.
No, I'll be good to win.
And it's no fun.
I'll be good, except that we play blackjack. Now that you're a movie star, 25-1 on the blackjack.
All right.
Oh, no. Are you kidding? Is that what he does?
He loves handing me his money.
Why doesn't he just show up and give you his wallet and then watch TV?
Stupid. Give me time.
What he does is we start playing blackjack, right? And he says, Howard, if you bet $10 right now, $50, 25-1 odds. And you know what happens? I get a blackjack, and he loves giving me money. And he ends up giving me like $3,000.
Nah.
Yeah. I'll play with you in that game.
Yeah, it's great odds.
Robin, I'll play you in basketball.
I don't want your... Now that's a match.
Oh.
Can you beat Dominic?
Oh, of course I can beat Dominic.
All right, Dominic, you going to play Robin? How much money?
Robin, you play me, really?
Yes.
Really?
Are you serious?
Serious.
I just have to tell you that I was almost a professional player.
Yeah, almost. Let's play
so
next week.
So was I.
You missed by 300.
Next week, you're on.
It's a deal, Robin.
All right, we're in the tournament.
We got so much going on today. Yeah. A lot of it involves you.
Ah.
So I will tell you everything that's going on.
Oh, I got to tell you.
I hope you're well rested today. What is it? What's the news break? But
Dominic called, didn't want to go on the air, from his doctor's office.
Oh.
He threw at his knee.
He will never play. He will never be around me again. He is dead to me. He is dead to me.
He canceled, John? He canceled.
See, I'm now ready. I wasted an afternoon practicing.
Oh, he is dead to me.
He claims that he's getting shots in his knee right now,
okay.
And he's going to call back as soon as he gets
it. He is dead to me. John, listen to everyone.
See, I can't take this. Either we're playing or we're
not.
I cannot take maybes. I don't know if I can get here from the doctor's office.
He is dead to me. He will never, ever be in my company again. Period.
No more scores parties, no more cards,
no more card games, nothing. I told him this. I said, don't screw with me.
It's a major event.
It's a major event. We've booked cameras.
We hired two extra camera crews.
No. He is dead to me. If he isn't there today at the basketball game, he is dead to me. Don't take his calls. Don't get involved with him. I'm having a card game Friday. He does not play.
Okay, what?
This was his idea.
Yeah, hold on a second. If Dominic's listening now, or if anybody knows where to get Dominic, he better call in the next 10 minutes to tell us that he's coming to this event.
Yeah, I don't care either way. It's fine. It's the pressure off Robin. And quite frankly...
Well, yeah, but I got a guy sitting out in the green.
We got Len Berman here.
Went out of his way to get here.
Yeah, I tell you something. He is dead to me. I don't care what doctor.
He didn't have to be involved in this at all.
Yeah, who asked him? Don't get me all set up and then cancel at the last minute.
What time did he call, John?
He called 5 minutes ago. He didn't want to come in the air because he was in the doctor's office.
Yeah, he didn't want to come on the air.
And
he better get his ass down here. Here's Dominic, and he's walking fine. And he's dancing. It was a big goof. Gemma?
Listen, Howard, I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think that's very nice to do to Dominic. He's a good friend of yours.
No, he's dead to me.
And listen, wait, let me finish what I'm saying. He's a good friend of yours, and he must have a reason.
No, he's not a good friend of mine.
Doctor's office. Howard,
I saw him yesterday. He was fine.
Attack in this thing. This is not.
Here he is. Here's Dominic.
Looks like he's walking.
And he's
fine.
Walking fine. Wow. He's dancing. It was a
never
big goof.
Mind,
oh, wait, here's Gary.
He's goofing.
He's goofing.
Come on, sit down.
What is it, Gary?
I said to Dominic, you know, I go, what is wrong with you?
What did you do, Dominic?
Get your
microphone. Wait, hang my mom up?
Oh,
I'm not hanging her up. Dominic, tell us what's going on here.
I'm ready to play.
Ah, thank you.
I feel fabulous.
Right.
I would never let you down. I love you more than a brother.
Thank you. So this was a shtick you were
just
putting on?
Just a little shtick.
He's trying to psych me out. That's what he's trying to do.
To be doing, Dominic.
Playing basketball?
What are you saying? What are you saying? Dominic shouldn't play?
That's right.
Mrs. Stern, I do have to say that the folks at E sort of agree with you because we did get, we got an ambulance and an oxygen tank, and at first it started as a joke,
right.
But then Doug from E said, Dominic might genuinely need oxygen.
What
well, first of all,
no oxygen
Howard.
During the game.
First
I love
all,
it.
Howard?
Yeah.
Howard,
you have lost a lot of weight.
Do I look good?
No.
Oh, get out of here, Ma. Are you kidding me?
What did she say? She would not allow?
Not allow Dominic. Dominic's a grown man.
I have an entire outfit.
Right.
It's actually been prepared.
Well, wear the outfit. We'll take pictures.
He doesn't have to play hard.
Everybody. This It'll is... be a lot of fun, and you don't have to knock yourself out.
Well, I'm giving Howard the front of my T-shirt.
Let me see what your T-shirt says.
And I want to give it to
It says, down with Blaze.
Dominic, you Howard so much.
And my horse is on his back with his
Ma,
horse in the air.
Dominic's not doing this for me. He called up and challenged Robin.
Well, sometimes you do something, that you know, and then you think about it, and it's not the right thing. And
Dominic, do you want to back out of this?
Absolutely. Not.
Ma, will you attend the funeral?
Please, Howard.
Oh, oh please. He's going to be fine. Stop it. Ma, I got to go. I don't want you psyching Dominic out. Thank you.
Well,
what do you mean, psych him out?
I think Dominic should listen, and so should you.
All right, thank you.
Oh, boy, now I'm worried.
Bye-bye.
All right.
I wasn't worried
my mother.
This.
The hell is she popping in with?
Oh, no. What if something happens to
do
me?
Do you know how to play this game?
No, I've never played before.
You're lying. I know you're lying.
You know,
where is Len Berman, who's going to be doing the play-by-play?
Let's have him come in.
Now, Len Berman has agreed to do play-by-play. I will do color. What do you mean?
What, like there's going to be some color?
Like I'll say stuff to Len during the game like, hey, Len, do you see Robin's breasts? How beautiful.
Yeah.
Do you see Dominic's breasts?
Yeah.
How beautiful.
Hi, Len.
Here's Len. Obviously, he's been out in the sun. He looks tan and healthy. What, you have a facelift? You look terrific.
Jesus.
Len's in better shape than either one of us. He should
I know.
Play.
Maybe you should play, Len.
Here. Unbelievable.
Yeah. Len Berman is, of course, the NBC sportscaster here in New York. He is a noted authority on basketball.
Howard, what are we doing?
Football
here?
And all gaming.
Isn't this ridiculous?
You're a bright guy. Let me ask you a couple questions. I think you're one of the top sportscasters
Thank
in the
you,
country.
Man.
Dominic is one of the top attorneys. Robin, one of the top newscasters. Let me just say something here.
They're all the top, right here.
Let me say something. And stop showing off your body. Look at
these great. Look at the studio. This is beautiful.
Beautiful, isn't it?
I love the movie, by the way.
Thank you very much.
Robin, you were great.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you. I coached her. Now, listen.
Well, you should have helped me with basketball.
Yeah.
Can you play? Len, because he's been working out for a day.
No.
A whole day.
I Len, worked out for a half hour.
Is there any truth to what my mother's saying? Is Dominic so bloated and heavy that he could actually have a heart attack during the game? It's only 7 points. I mean, we're not talking about a long game.
No, as long as he doesn't drive to the hoop.
Let me ask you this, Len. Excuse me for 1 minute. Can he damage the floor?
Oh.
No.
And therefore cause Robin interruption
somebody,
play.
He's
a problem.
This is a problem.
Are we going to go for all
the structure of that building?
Len, I see you looking.
Here's what I'm
looking Dominic over. Say what you're concerned
about. Well, here's
what
I'm concerned about. Because, you know, when we were playing as kids, everyone would say, yeah, he can, but he can't go to his left.
Right.
I mean, this guy, I'm not sure if he can go anywhere.
He can head right for the pastrami table.
That's a concern.
Jealousy
is a concern.
Right. So what I'm saying here is that you got a guy, Dominic, who weighs, take a guess, 300 pounds?
Oh, stop.
No.
600.
Stand up. Stand up and weigh in.
I'm not weighing in.
No, but go ahead.
I'd say 280.
Oh, please. 350.
350.
What do you think he weighs? Seriously, Jackie.
350.
360.
Get out of here.
That's the crazy.
I weigh 200 and I'm half your size.
But that's the silliest conversation.
Get the scale.
I'm not getting on
a
scale.
Well, why? Why? Do you weigh over 300 pounds?
I'm not getting on a scale no matter what. I'm playing basketball.
All right. I say we call the game. Dominic, I don't like the way you look. I'm excited to be here at the Club Reebok. This is truly a monumental occasion because we have somebody who weighs, I would guess, and now that we have the privacy of this room, I would guess that Dominic weighs over 300 pounds.
Do you think so?
Literally, I would say.
Tell me what you think of Dominic as an opponent.
Well, he's formidable because there's a lot of court coverage. You know, he's a very broad man, a very wide man, and the object is to get to the basket, so I will have to go around him. There's no going straight to the basket. So that's one thing that bothers me.
I expect to win. I'm here for victory, and I am going to have to unfortunately jeopardize my friendship. I love Robin dearly. But this is basketball, and it's for money.
My job is to win.
Basically, we're here today in the event of Dominic Barber having a heart attack because of the stress that will incur while playing this game today. We have full advanced life support complement right here. I think we're prepared for everything, hopefully.
My guess is that Dominic is the most inept athlete I've ever had the fortune of covering at a sports event. Yes.
Dominic's a little bit taller. I don't think Dominic has any agility whatsoever. But I think just being a guy, you got to have some shot. And Robin has admitted that she has no shot whatsoever. But, you know, she definitely can get around him. I think she's more agile than him. It's going to be tough.
There's no way to know what's going to happen because Dominic hasn't been square with us about whether he was torn and yeah, right. So we have no idea if he played as a kid. If he played as a kid and has any of the skills, you would have from playing basketball.
However, unless, you know, you got to have some mobility. The only mobility he might have putting his arms over his head is if he's reaching for a pizza box falling off the back of a truck.
All right, let's start the game. Good luck.
Well, this is it. Here we go.
He doesn't look that bad, Dominic, in his sweats. I'm kind of surprised. Here goes Robin.
Robin? Well, she's staying on the outside. She doesn't want to show all of her offense at once. Dominic with a laid-back defense, kind of a junky, jolly kind of approach to playing defense.
He's not guarding her tightly.
It's too bad it's not like a time game because then she could hold it to the last few seconds and shoot. At some point, there should be some offense, but that's just a personal opinion here.
I noticed Robin's breasts are going up and down as she...
I noticed Robin has used both hands on the dribble. She's now backed in. Dominic has gone for
Dominic
the steal.
Dominic stole the ball.
Oh. One steal for Dominic. Dominic,
she's
really a right-handed dribble.
Come on, she's hitting
it. We should point out the referee is Bucky Nickow, who has yet to call a foul. Despite the pleading of Dominic. Dominic, inside move. Oh, and Dominic, first basket. And I believe Las Vegas said that Robin would score the first basket.
Dominic
upset
got a,
in the making.
Hey, not throwing the ball, Dominic.
He hit me about 10 times.
Wait, with Dominic oxygen? Looks like he's going to pass out.
Well, it's a good thing we have medical people here, Howard.
Dominic, are you out of breath? Here he goes, outside shot. Misses
air ball. His shooting percentage just dropped to 50%.
Did she have to give me it?
No.
Robin has yet to get a shot off in this game, Howard.
That's true.
Dominic with the steal early on the turnover.
Here goes Robin. She's in layup position, and then she kind of backed away.
Dominic's giving her the outside shot. He's conceding the long shot. Robin yet to... There it goes. Robin's first shot of the game.
Ooh.
Dominic with the aggressive rebound. Again, Dominic asking for traveling. It looks like he's appealing right now.
I mean, he thinks he's in court.
Yeah. Oh, took his eye off the ball
the
for a second.
All the way back.
On,
he's backing in. Backing in. Fakes with one hand. The fadeaway. Robin the rebound. No, Robin,
Robin,
you have to take it back.
No, you have to take it back.
Take it back.
It's 2 points for Dominic. You got to take it back.
Right.
Well, why would Dominic get the points?
Why would Dominic get 2 points? He's getting the points. No, you don't get the points.
Nothing.
Bucky making up the rules.
That's
no.
The rules.
No.
Bucky, I never heard of that.
No.
The score is 2-0. Dominic.
Let's go.
There's some confusion on the court.
That was a good recap there, Howard.
I thought that was a travel.
Oh, absolutely.
Good call by Bucky.
Wow. No, it was a he traveled. Traveling call.
Traveled.
On the turnover, first turnover charge.
Crazy.
To Dominic.
Dominic, be a gentleman.
Oh, right. Robin goes into that soft offense again, which is good because Dominic has the soft defense. So it's kind of an offense tailor-made for this defense, but she has to shoot the outside shot.
Yes!
Long, but Robin grabs the offensive
rebound.
First offensive rebound of the action.
Robin shot and missed, but she got a rebound.
And I noticed Robin's picking it up here. She started slow. Dominic with the defense. Robin tries to get the shot off. And Dominic, jump ball is good.
What a physical game.
Dominic claiming that he fouled her, and Dominic giving Robin the ball. Right. Giving Robin every opportunity here in the early going.
Here goes Robin up to the net.
Robin is in the lane.
Taking her time. I like that. I like it.
Robin over.
Yes.
Shooting long again. This time Dominic races for the rebound. Slowly takes the ball out. I don't think he went far enough.
He didn't go back.
I went back.
Bucky allowing him some slack here. A hook shot from Dominic. Hits the side of the backboard. Gets his own rebound. Shoots an air ball. Robin can shoot.
Robin
can shoot that. Robin didn't understand it. She can shoot immediately on an air ball.
I think we ought to call the game on account of Dominic's heart attack.
All right, Robin controlling the offense now. She's backed in toward Dominic, went for the steal. Robin's shot is short. That was an air ball.
touched a camera crew member, so Dominic
right.
is going to take it out.
Would have been out anyway.
Robin, Dominic,
guard him, Robin.
Dominic with the shot.
Uh-oh.
Is no good. Yeah. Robin, another rebound.
Take it back. Dominic shoots and misses. Robin now with the ball, dribbling back.
Yeah. Howard, I think you have to jump in and call a lot of this action because he's going to go for a while. Okay. Robin with the shot from the foul line.
Ooh.
No good. Just a little long. Dominic the rebound. Dominic trying to move the ball outside and does so. So it's Dominic ball. He leads 2-0. It's the first to get to 7 points. Dominic backs in. Backs in. Still backing in. Big back-to-back in with. Turns around. Shoots over Robin. Off the side of the backboard again. Dominic has hit the side of the backboard twice, which is a new record.
Len, I've never seen a play like this from Dominic. I don't even understand his strategy. Is there a strategy?
He's out of breath. Oh, he's winded.
He's out of breath. He's winded. Winded. He's winded.
Robin should take it right to him.
Take it to the hoop, Robin. He's winded.
Robin from the foul line.
Yes!
It rolls up. No good.
Shoots and misses.
Robin with her closest opportunity. Those shots will eventually fall. Dominic called for not taking the ball back far enough.
You got to get everything back.
Show him the line, Bucky.
Well, I thought part of his body was back far enough. Maybe it's...
Yeah, I think his ass was behind the line. The rest of him was...
Dominic, the foul line shot, another air ball.
Robin's
goes out of bounds. Robin's ball out.
We've seen two points in about 10 minutes worth of play.
Robin goes after him.
And
she boards him into the wall.
It's your ball, Robin. Dribble. Take it to the hoop. He's out of breath.
Robin starts to move in tentatively. She stops. Takes the shot.
Yes.
Oh, no good. Robin chases down the rebound and Dominic rips it away from her. We've yet to have a foul call.
Yeah,
cross check right there. Sure. Here goes Dominic. He's got a breakaway on the layup, and he's strong with the shot.
He missed it. Hurry, Robin.
Dominic missing the wide open shot. Dominic's out of breath. Great opportunity for Quivers here. Robin at the foul line. Robin going for the tie.
Yes.
She's short.
We're gonna be here all day,
yeah.
Len, you better call in sick.
Yeah, I know. Dominic with the layup. He hits it. 4-0, Dominic.
Uh-oh. All right, I say we call the game. Dominic, I don't like the way you're looking. Hold it, I want the medics brought in to look over Dominic.
Yeah, a medical timeout is called for.
Rest? Rest him?
No!
I don't like the way Dominic's looking.
Are you all right?
Dominic does look out of weight.
Sit down, Dominic.
Sure?
We do allow medical timeouts, Dominic.
This is like the infirm. Here goes Dominic.
From outside, yeah. And no, we started out being.
Robin, just run up to the hoop.
It started out being on the Stern Show. It's going to wind up on ER.
I know. I'm concerned about Dominic's health. I really am.
Robin, short again.
Dominic, fall back here.
I'm a little concerned. On the Schneid. I'm concerned here. A shutout would be embarrassing.
Yeah. I just think if Robin worked the ball inside and took her time, she'd be able to do it.
You know, if Dominic can't continue, that's a forfeit, Howard.
I say, Dominic, forfeit the game if you're not feeling good.
Hey, this is
Dominic trying to move the microphones out of the way. The outside shot is no good.
No good.
Robin looks fresh, though. So
Robin, perhaps, run on him.
Perhaps the longer this goes, the more of an advantage Robin will have. She looks good. Robin from the foul line. This looks good, Howard.
Yes! 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 Not embarrassment.
Cuts the deficit in half. Cuts it to 4-2. Quivers again from the foul line for two in a row. No. Dominic, the rebound. Dominic with the lead, 4-2. He starts to back in again. Robin, tight defense from Robin. Good defensive move. She's leaning on him. Dominic with the fake, shoots, off, no good. So Robin, once again, with an outstanding opportunity to tie this match. I would say that Robin is the crowd favorite at this point, wouldn't you?
Well, we'd like to see her win.
And she hits it. Robin ties the game at 4.
Robin coming to life.
This game is even. It's now a 3-point game, ladies and gentlemen.
Len, you got to be impressed.
Oh, now he plays defense.
Bounce it off his belly.
Bounce it off his belly.
No, that's a discontinued dribble.
Bounce it off his belly.
X-rated, I may add.
That's a good idea. Robin, if he ties you up like that,
bounce it off him. Absolutely.
Run.
Howard, I thought that was excellent advice.
I know. Well, Robin's uptight right at this point. She's sensing victory.
Well,
Dominic looks like he's going to collapse.
Dominic with an outside shot.
He hits it.
Dominic now within 1 point of victory.
One point of victory.
Commanding six. This is for the win, ladies and gentlemen.
He did it. He won.
8-4.
8-4.
8-4. Do I have to high five him?
Oh, my goodness.
8-4. Robin's upset. No handshake.
Robin, what do you say?
The sportsmanship is lacking. Robin goes after him.
Hey, another knee.
And she boards him into the wall. I didn't know this was kickboxing, Howard. You told me it was basketball.
What is going on? Hey, easy. Wait a second. What's
Robin with the schoolyard kneeing tactics. Man, this is clearly against the rules.
Grab your butt.
Oh, your butt cheese.
Dominic, you know what you did.
I'm surprised. I don't know. I went to say congratulations. She flipped out. I don't know what happened. Seriously, I don't know what she's talking about.
Dominic had said to me a couple of days ago that during the game, he was going to hit me on the ass, and that's how he was going to distract me. And I told him that was unacceptable and that that should not happen, and I wouldn't be calling the police, that I would take care of it on the court. And at the end of the game, when we walked over to the table and we were talking about the end of the game and all of that, he hit me on my ass. And I told him, well, I told you what would happen, and so I took care of it.
Dominic, congratulations on your win. You did it. You went up there like
a man. You beat a girl.
You beat a girl. Big deal. Don't get too excited.
But I beat a beautiful girl.
Are you going to be okay, Dominic?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I'm surprised at the outcome. I really thought she was going to win. Sucks.
Dominic, be honest.
You're a cheater, but I will shake your hand. You cheated and you lied. But that's all right.
But the best part of the game for me was when Robin went after Dominic to knee him in the groin. That was quite exciting for me.
Dominic hit two shots to win the game that were like, he might as well have thrown him up with his eyes closed.
We say goodbye from the club Reebok from the big match between Robin Quivers and Dominic Barbara. I'm looking for a rematch at some point.
I think it's in the cards. When I do my sports shows, our byword is nobody got hurt. The key thing is nobody got hurt. So everyone goes home happy.
You did pretty good.
Yeah.
Wow, you're more...
Easy.
All right? You can't say that on the air.
He was pushing me around.
Yeah.
It was not easy to be in there with this 300-pound gorilla.
Robin from the foul line. This looks good, Howard.
Yes!
You did pretty good.
Yeah.
Wow, you're more...
Easy.
All right? You can't say that on the air.
He was pushing me around.
Yeah.
It was not easy to be in there with this 300-pound gorilla.
You did pretty good.
Yeah. Doesn't matter. I didn't want to be there.
So Robin and Dominic start playing this game, all right? I mean... You know, okay, Dominic's obese and everything, and he's
but
uptight.
But he's the one who made the challenge.
That's right.
I'm there, I'm trying to play as best I can.
Yeah, and he's uptight because, you know, he's a guy and he wants to be able to beat Robin. But, you know, you have to have a certain nonchalance when you play a girl like you don't care that much.
Right,
you know?
It was absolutely outrageous the way he was acting.
He starts, Robin dribbles the ball, Dominic steals the ball, right? Robin's never dribbled. He steals the ball, and you had to see him steal the ball. It's amazing. I'm going to play all the tapes. It's just, it's frightening. He steals the ball, starts dribbling. This is the first basket, right? So he starts dribbling, and he starts screaming, "She's fouling me! She's fouling
she's
me!
She's pushing me!
You're hitting me! She's hitting me, ref! Come on! She's hitting me! She's hitting me!"
I mean, like a baby. And she was guarding him close. I didn't see you. I watched the tape.
I couldn't push him if my life
depended
on it.
Right. So he starts screaming and screaming for the ref to call a foul.
He's yelling at Buck.
He puts the ball up. He gets the ball in. Okay? He shoots the ball. He gets it in. He takes the ball, he throws it at Bucky, the ref.
How about a foul there? You watching?
Hey, Dominic's getting upset.
She hit me about 10 times.
I was like, oh my God.
I thought he was goofing around when he was yelling at first, and then I realized he was like,
he's dead
so
serious.
Competitive.
Yeah, competitive. I mean, he's a guy. What's his, he's playing a girl.
You know what was more
a girl who can't play.
Right.
Period.
Meanwhile, Robin scored 4 points on him.
It really could have gone.
And you know what? You were a lot of your shots were right on the rim.
I know.
It could have gone either way.
If they had gone in, I'd have beat him.
There was a point where it was like 4-4. Robin could have gotten a basket in.
Two points were taken away from me because I don't even know how to play the game.
No,
I put a ball up that wasn't supposed to be in play.
Yeah.
And I made a basket.
Robin, you have to take it back.
No, you have to take it back.
Take it back.
You got to take it back.
Right. Well, why would Dominic get the points?
Why would Dominic get 2 points?
He's get the points.
No, you don't get the points.
What? Nothing.
That was the most embarrassing.
I should have gotten points for anything I got. I could do.
Yeah.
You guys cheated me.
When Robin
no,
forgot to...
No, why should I be forced to play a game I don't know how to play?
Well, they told you. What was that part with the rules at the beginning where they explained that to
you? No, you have to
they
go back.
They didn't explain
no, they
it boring.
Did.
I need to know how this game is played.
Here's what the rules are. You get two shots on. If you go into the basket and you get slapped, that's two shots. In other words, if it's in the act of shooting, you get two. If it's just a foul outside here, you get one.
All right, Dominic puts up a shot and misses the rim entirely.
The
you
rim
don't
ball.
Have to take air ball. You don't have to take it back.
All right, I can just shoot from
right
wherever
there, right.
I
that's right.
What does winners out mean?
Winners out means
the basket,
if you shoot the ball... Go ahead, Bucky.
You shot the ball. You did a layup. The ball went in. Now you get the ball. You get to take the ball back.
You get it.
Now,
you
don't
right.
turn it
the point is that this is a guy who's played before. He's playing a woman who's only held a basketball twice.
I agree.
They
should have
given me credit for anything.
Why did you say that going in?
I tried, but everybody was, no, you're going to play a game. And well, Dominic was saying he couldn't play any better than
lose
me.
Lose graciously.
Dominic's not the only competitive one.
And this was not my doing. I didn't put myself in this game. I got drafted into this game you guys at a card game.
Are you really that upset?
And I'm really upset. That's
about
right.
Losing?
No, just about why put me into your stupid crap at a card game.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
Don't include me in. I don't include you in my crap when I'm with women.
Didn't you think she was into this?
I thought you were into it.
No, I do whatever's good for the show. But
oh,
next
good.
Time.
And we all
leave
do.
Leave me out of any discussions you're having at a card game because that has nothing to do with the show.
Okay.
Who knew?
Who knew?
Wow, you're more... Pushing me around.
Easy.
All right?
You can't say that on the air.
He was pushing me around.
Yeah.
It was not easy to be in there with this 300-pound gorilla.
You did pretty good.
Yeah. Doesn't matter. I didn't want to be there.
Robin, you play me really?
Yes.
Really?
Are you serious?
Serious.
Next week, you're on.
It's a deal, Robin.
All right, we're in the tournament. Basketball is not anything I ever wanted to do.
What is it?
The 300-pound gorilla's online, too.
Hey,
you should be ashamed of yourself, Dominic. You really should.
Yeah,
you played like a baby.
Yeah, tell you that I beat him up.
Listen, I expected nothing less from this. However,
yeah.
Robin is the toughest lady you ever saw.
Oh.
She was punching me in the back.
Right.
No,
right,
she wasn't.
Punching you.
I saw that.
And when the game was over, she beat me to the wall. And was
you're lucky you're
kick.
Still here.
Now, how about when he, and then at the end of the game, he grabbed your ass.
Yeah.
And then you beat him in the balls.
That's right.
Three times.
Well, I wanted to make
Dominic, we got the e-cameras have it on tape.
Did you get him?
Three different angles you grabbed her ass.
Oh, that's not even true.
It's
see,
so true.
You're a never mind. He really pisses me off.
Are you embarrassed that you lost?
I have no desire to play basketball. It was a waste of my time to have to even be involved in it.
She doesn't want to show all of her offense at once. Dominic with a laid-back defense, kind of a junky, jolly kind of approach to playing defense.
He's not guarding her tightly.
It's too bad it's not like a time game because then she could hold it to the last few seconds and shoot. At some point, there should be some offense, but that's just a personal opinion here.
I noticed Robin's breasts are going up and down as she...
I noticed Robin has used both hands on the dribble. She's now backed in. Dominic has gone for
Dominic
the steal.
Dominic stole the ball.
Oh. One steal for Dominic. Dominic...
She's
really a right-handed dribble.
Come on, she's hitting
we should point out the referee is Bucky Nickow, who has yet to call a foul, despite the pleading of Dominic. Dominic, inside move. Oh, and Dominic, first basket. And I believe Las Vegas said that Robin would score the first basket.
Dominic got it.
When I was trying to get my shots up, and it was very
trying to get
my
shots in.
Robin was kicking and pushing.
Kicking?
Threatening. Oh.
No, you were acting like a baby.
Right. Dominic, know, you're out of your mind.
Would you have liked me to lose? Is that what you
No, said? No, but you should have played fair.
Who'd you beat, Dominic? Who did you beat? How did you beat?
I beat a very tough competitor.
You beat somebody who never played basketball. That's a big deal.
I never played.
Yeah, right.
Wow.
Look at this. What's going on?
Very competitive.
Here.
Very competitive.
Robin, you are incredible.
Very competitive.
Like I said, leave me out of your little boy's games. I don't bother you. Don't bother
You're
me.
You're playing him in ice hockey next week.
Yes, you are. Right. I'll put the puck right
you,
somewhere, but you won't like it.
Oh, yes, I will.
When Robin made the basket without bringing it back, and Dominic screamed for 10 minutes that he wanted those 2 points to count for him,
right.
That was such an embarrassment.
Yeah, I know. That was embarrassing.
4-0. That's the rules.
Right from the get-go, we were giving the rules to Robin. And Dominic's on the other side of the gym, and I go, Dominic, come over here. He goes, I'm not hearing any of this. You're going to have to do it all over again.
Well, I'm not there.
He misses the shot.
Come on. You're right.
He doesn't hit the basket.
He doesn't have the rim.
Hold it. Let me clear it up. Let me clear it up.
I go, well, come over. And Dominic is sitting there shining.
Pouting.
Polishing his glasses. Doing nothing.
Right.
But he can't come over to us. We have to wait for him.
Yeah, he was Mr. Attitude right from the very beginning.
Oh, absolutely.
Psyching the game out.
Yeah. It was a lot of fun, Dominic.
Psyching the game out.
Robin, I'm really surprised that you're this upset. I had no idea.
I have no desire to play basketball. Why would I be there?
Yeah, but a lot of us on the show...
If I decide to do something, then I do it.
But how many of us on the show do stuff that we don't want to do?
I don't care what you do, Gary. I just said what I do.
Then why did you do it?
Because we were already into it, and I said, what the hell?
You could have said no.
Had any idea.
You could always say no.
Robin, you play me, really?
Yes.
Really? Are you serious?
Serious. All of a sudden, it was just, I didn't know this was cooked up at a card game. All of a sudden, Dominic's calling up and saying, Robin,
it's cooked up right on the air.
I'm cooking. He just called in and said, I'll play Robin basketball.
Yeah, that's exactly what it
happened. How is that cooking? Out of the blue, Dominic calls in and say, I want to play Robin basketball?
Exactly.
Bull. I don't buy it.
I would admit it if I cooked it up. I just never thought of it.
You don't remember what you guys say at your silly card game.
No, I'm telling you the truth.
That's where he got the idea.
You calling me a liar?
No, I'm just saying.
I'm telling you the truth.
That's what he said to me. And I'm sitting here all week.
He also said he didn't palm your ass, didn't he?
I'm also sitting here all week. I don't have tape of that.
Did he say you're not palm your ass?
I don't have tape of that.
So you're calling me a liar, right?
I'm telling you.
Are you calling me a liar?
I was sitting here all week.
Are you calling me a liar?
How I got into a basketball game.
Are you calling me a liar?
How did I get into a basketball game?
Dominic,
I don't want to play basketball.
I'll tell you how you play basketball. Dominic called in and you agreed.
Fine.
Don't blame yourself.
No, everybody all jumped on it like, oh, what a great idea.
It was everybody's fault.
Did you ever express to anybody at any point that you didn't want to do it?
Yes, ask Ganji.
Really? You expressed it to Ganji?
What would you tell Ganji and not me or Howard or Jackie?
We had no idea.
I was going to go through with it, but I wasn't because it was already a thing on the air.
But you agreed to it on the air.
Of course.
Why would you say I don't want to play?
This is a stupid show, and I do what goes on in the show.
All right, so don't whine about it.
Don't ever bring me into your games again.
Who brought you into it?
You guys were at a card game.
Wrong.
Talking about who Dominic could beat at basketball.
That's a lie.
That's what he said.
Would this be totally different if you had a won?
No.
Yes.
What was I saying on Thursday?
Absolutely.
It does not matter.
Are you embarrassed that you lost?
I have no desire to play basketball. It was a waste of my time to have to even be involved in it.
Are you embarrassed that you lost?
No.
Wow.
But it was a game I don't play. And I don't like to play games of sport like that. I don't like to play team sports.
Did you not like playing tennis at the Nassau Coliseum?
That was something I decided to do. And I like tennis.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Do you ever compete with your horse or just ride for fun?
I do both because that's what I decided to do.
Oh, I see.
I think we're all totally shocked because we had no idea.
That's right.
You had a great time.
Can't read your mind.
She
go ahead.
She was saying when I went to practice with her the other day that she was pretty adamant about not wanting to play.
So why didn't she tell us?
I don't know. You know, I thought she
Dominic. I don't try to hang you up after I say I'll do something. It was in the heat of the moment on the air, but then I'm like, what the hell am I doing? I hate basketball.
Yeah, so don't be so uptight about it.
I'm not uptight. I'm just telling you from now on.
You sound a little
keep
uptight.
Keep me out of it.
Keep you out of the, what, everything on the show?
That's right.
Robin goes into that soft offense again, which is good because Dominic has the soft defense. So it's kind of an offense tailor-made for this defense, but she has to shoot the outside shot.
Yes!
Long, but Robin grabs the offensive rebound. First offensive rebound of the action.
Robin shot and missed, but she got a rebound.
And I noticed Robin's picking it up here. She started slow. Dominic with the defense. Robin tries to get the shot off. And Dominic, jump ball is good.
What a physical game.
You'd be lucky I didn't break a nail.
we didn't think in terms of tragedy.
Howard, I think you have to jump in and call a lot of this action because he's going to go for a while. Okay. Robin with the shot from the foul line.
Ooh.
No good. Just a little long. Dominic the rebound. Dominic trying to move the ball outside and does so. So it's Dominic ball. He leads 2-0. It's the first to get to 7 points. Dominic backs in, still backing in. Big back-to-back in with. Turns around, shoots over Robin, off the side of the backboard again. Dominic has hit the side of the backboard twice, which is a new record.
Len, I've never seen a play like this from Dominic. I don't even understand his strategy. Is there a strategy?
He's out of breath. Oh, he's winded.
He's out of breath. He's winded.
Robin should take it right to him.
Take it to the hoop, Robin. He's winded.
Robin from the foul line.
Yes!
It rolls up. No good.
Shoots and misses.
Robin with her closest opportunity. Those shots will eventually fall. Dominic called for not taking the ball back far enough.
I'm not uptight. I'm just telling you from now on.
You sound a little
uptight. Keep me out of it.
Keep you out of the, what, everything on the show?
That's right.
Robin? Right. Yeah, okay.
You could have chickened out.
Yeah.
Robin. Chickened out. See there?
You gotta be a man. Step up to the plate. All I'm going to say, Dominic.
Wait, Robin, would you feel
I'm not way? Speaking to you.
Dominic, you played like a baby. You played like a girl.
You're hitting me. She's hitting me, Robin.
And I got absolutely nothing out of it. What do I get out of it?
My headphones just actually hurt.
She's I don't is care, Gary.
Is Belzer here? Because Robin's ready for competition.
Yeah, I know. Wait, hold on.
She better win Robin, today, man.
We're gonna play Jeopardy.
She almost didn't like the Jeopardy yesterday until she won.
I love Jeopardy.
Is it okay if these guys play or should I send them home?
Oh, screw you, Gary.
Robin, can I say something? Yes. Jesus. Before I get off the phone, Robin.
Yes.
And I really mean it sincerely because I don't want you mad at me.
Yes.
I beat you. Goodbye.
Oh, big deal.
He's so proud of himself. And you should see the look on his face when he wins.
He almost
died. Yeah.
When he sinks a basket.
He puts his fist up in the air.
He's Rocky.
He throws his chest out.
He's a 900-pound guy. He's Rocky.
I can't count those money, too.
I still say you could have beat him.
Yeah.
Doesn't it was very matter. Close. Could have gone either way.
Didn't want to be there.
Well, you were there. You put yourself there. Mm. You can't blame anybody but yourself.
I'm just saying, if it was cooked up at a card game, don't ever mention my name at one.
I don't care whatever's cooked up at a card game. If you say no, you don't play.
I don't want to hear it. I do not want to hear
it. You
could
have said no at any point.
Oh, just be quiet.
We cook up
Jackie.
Stuff all day, though.
I cannot believe the things that you guys have cooked up for me that I've never had any say in to do, like putting on turkey outfits and stuff like
that. We write bits all the time, and if you don't want to go into an outfit.
No, but I mean, listen, it's just, I never say these guys cook something up for me. Of course I do it for the good of the show. We all do stupid things for the good of the show. Do the Bubba Bully!
Suppose I'd gotten hurt. That idiot was pushing me around.
Nah, you had him under control. I saw what was going on.
I could have broken a nail. You'd be lucky I didn't break a nail.
We didn't think in terms of tragedy.
Yeah.
Jeez. Anything like that, and I would have been very upset.
No, you handled yourself fine.
You would have been upset.
Right now, I'm only mildly upset.
You know, I do have to say, you know, Doug, who works on E, his brother was one of the emergency guys there.
Yeah.
Just in case. And he said, you know, he's been doing this for a while. He said 2 minutes into the game, Dominic got the color and look of a guy who was out of, you know, who was looked like he might pass out for lack of oxygen.
Yeah, Dominic looked bad. I thought he was going to die.
They were really worried about him.
And yeah, Dominic's, I was.
He's playing it off now like I was fine, but he looked bad.
Uh-oh. All right, I say we call the game. Dominic, I don't like the way you're looking. Hold it. I want the medics brought in to look over Dominic.
Yeah. A medical timeout is called for.
He looked real bad. Wait till you see the tape. He's sweating so profusely. It looks like he just took a shower.
He was worried.
Didn't you say to me it looked like he took a shower?
Yes.
Yeah. And you know what? He said something to me after the game, which I know he'll deny now.
Yeah.
But he said to me, you know, he won the game sinking two quick Hail Mary baskets. And he said, if I didn't sink those two shots, I was just going to give it to her. I couldn't play anymore.
Right. Wow.
He was going to die.
Yeah, what if he didn't make those? The game would have gone on more.
He said,
I tell you something. He looked like death.
Yes, he did.
Like death.
It was great.
He was huffing and puffing. At least you weren't sweating.
Yeah, you never looked like you were out of breath once.
When he stole the ball, he was like huffing and puffing. And that was like the beginning of the game.
And then he was holding his side. You know, like when you get that pain in your side when you run 20 miles.
I'm running out of time. Yeah. We got to start Jeopardy.
Yep.
This is a big deal. Are you in any condition to play Jeopardy? Are you going to be able to win?
I have no idea. I was exasperated yesterday because I did not want to play basketball.
Well, you better shape up for Jeopardy. This is more pressure on you.
This is something I decided to do. Right. I have no problem with it.
I see.
But basketball, I don't even
big problem
hear
with that.
From.
I see.
From now on, just check with her, Helen.
Oh, check when?
Check
when before Dominic calls in?
Before you do it.
I'm never speaking to Dominic again. He can call all he wants.
Really?
I won't even notice he's there.
Robin starts to move in tentatively. She stops. Takes the shot.
Yes!
Oh, no good. Robin chases down the rebound, and Dominic rips it away from her. We've yet to have a foul call.
You have to play a girl, Dominic.
Close check right there.
Goodbye.
Here goes Dominic. He's got a breakaway on the layup, and he's strong with the shot. He missed it.
Hurry,
Dominic missing the wide open shot. Dominic's out of breath. Great opportunity for Quivers here. Robin at the foul line. Robin going for the tie. She's short.
We're going to be here all day, Len.
Yeah.
Len, you better call in sick.
Yeah, I know. Dominic with the layup. He hits it. 4-0, Dominic.
Uh-oh. All right, I say we call the game. Dominic, I don't like the way you're looking. Hold it. I want the medics brought in to look over Dominic.
Yeah, a medical timeout is called for.
You're saying she's already won an F Emmy?
She's been nominated three times in the last minute.
Dominic looks like he's going to collapse.
Dominic with an outside shot.
He hits it.
Dominic now within 1 point of victory.
One point of victory.
A commanding 6. This is for the win, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah! He did it. He won. 8-4. 8-4. 8-4.
Do I have to high five him?
Oh, my goodness.
8-4. Robin. Robin's upset.
Robin's
no handshake.
Robin, what do you say?
The sportsmanship is lacking. Robin goes after him. A knee.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
And she burns him into the wall. I didn't know this was kickboxing, Howard. You told me it was basketball.
What is going on? Hey, easy. Wait a second. What's
Robin with the schoolyard kneeing tactics. Man, this is clearly against the rules.
Dominic, you know what you did.
I saw the two of you did make up after the game. Somewhat.
Well, I didn't want him to die with bad words between
All right.
Dominic, be honest. You're a cheater, but I will shake your hand. You cheated and you lied. But that's all right.
That's sportsmanship.
Yes, what is it?
I do have to say one thing.
Yeah.
You know, the whole office is a buzz about this, and people were bringing up, like, remember when Ralph didn't want to take the polygraph?
Right. I didn't back out before.
No, but you screamed at those people, even though they didn't want to do it. You screamed at them that they were morons not to do it.
Didn't I do it?
No, but you're mad at us now.
Don't you see the difference? I did it.
No, the difference is you're mad at us now. I'd rather you didn't do it and not be mad at us.
No, I did it. So there. It has nothing to do with Ralph.
Gary's trying to make this rational.
I know.
Good luck.
You're saying Ralph didn't do something and I screamed at him, but I did it?
I didn't want to do it.
I can't wait to play this on the FMEs to have you hear how crazy this sounds.
Oh, fine.
No, because last time we did that category.
You're saying she's already won an FME?
She's been nominated three times in the last minute.
All the statues. Just give her the statue.
Get a shopping cart.
I want an actual statue.
Right. You're going to win this year.
Lifetime achievement.
I'll never be able to beat this.
Patty Hearst of the Raiders.
Well, look.
Against my will.
Oh, shut up, Jackie.
I'd like to compete.
I didn't say I didn't like to compete. I said I don't like to play basketball. If you're going to quote me correctly.
Should I decide to do something, I do it.
That's right. That's right. That's exactly how it works.
Yes.
It's okay. All I can eat is protein. It's a very convenient, easy way for me to have protein. I don't like eggs made by other people. I don't know what else to get. So I can just say, give me a couple of hamburgers. They don't put anything on it or in it. I can't have these additives that I wouldn't be sure of in some other thing. So it's a very easy way for me to stay on my diet and not be worried about what I'm eating. So what's the big deal?
I'm laughing because we're, you know, in the commercial. And Gary says to John, why did Robin give you $50? And he starts saying, oh, I get four hamburgers a day. And I'm like, what? Four hamburgers a day? And then you walk in right behind, you know, John's talking about you.
Just as he's disgusting.
Just as he's like squealing on you that you have four hamburgers a day. Right. And I'm laughing. I'm going... But then when you explained it, it made sense.
I know. He always likes to make me out to be.
Yeah, like I said, Robin's eating four hamburgers a day.
I could show you them right now. You would not be impressed.
You would not be impressed. I got to get a friggin' four hamburgers.
Four hamburgers a day. What do you want from me? I mean, you know.
They're
not
hamburgers on buns. They're four burgers sitting in a plate full of lettuce.
And that's
in a less insane.
But I didn't know she was doing Atkins. That's all you're allowed to eat all day.
No, I know. But all I said
is. We made it seem like she was eating, packing down four Big Macs a day.
You guys said, why did you give me 50?
I didn't say anything. I was busy reading. You and Gary started. And then Robin walks. I have to cover for you morons, because it may seem like you were bad-mouthing Robin.
No, I just said to you what it's for.
No, you were like, oh, you get a four freaking hamburgers
a day. I don't care. She knows I order them for. It's no big secret.
You know? She doesn't want everyone knowing she's eating four hamburgers a day.
I don't care what people Girls know, but like I'm not that. Eating them. I just showed him six hamburgers. I'm not eating any of them.
All right, so then I'm just ordering so you could save them in your tray.
That's right.
All right, so, you know, Howard, she's the one telling me to get four burgers. You'd assume she's eating them, all right? In fact, you know what? You know what's wrong? The other day, I got two one day. Then you came back and said, get me two more. Remember
right,
that?
Because I didn't bring breakfast then.
All right, so she had two for breakfast, two for lunch.
I didn't eat the other two. I took them home. You don't know what I'm eating. That's what I'm saying. Stop telling people what I'm eating.
All right, so why don't you just order two at your house? How come I'm ordering here?
See, I told you
because
Robin doesn't like you talking about her hamburgers.
Get them for me here.
It's easier for me. You can't order two burgers.
Where's she going to get them? You to get them.
She likes how you do it.
Any deli delivers, Howard.
Why does it matter to him how many I get?
It doesn't.
But he's going around broadcasting it.
Yeah, I know.
I knew you didn't like it.
It doesn't matter.
You're woofing down four hamburgers a day.
I'm woofing down four hamburgers a day.
See, girls don't like you to talk
about
stuff.
I'm not woofing. You want to see six hamburgers? I'm not eating any of them.
Maybe you should keep your mouth shut.
Okay.
You're saving up.
It's just, this is what kills me. He sits around, I don't know what he eats, but everybody's so f***ing,
I'm going to have a salad.
You don't know what he eats, but what? I had to bleep you. You used the F words. Everyone is so hot.
Look how upset you get over food.
I am so sick of everybody being so fascinated by everything I do.
It's not only
watch
you.
Watch me like I'm a... Now I'm going to say the F word.
See, girls don't like when you...
Like a I'm under a microscope.
Now do you understand?
No, it's not even about what I eat.
Now do you understand?
Every single thing I do. It's where I go.
You're a star.
Who I'm with. What
Listen, you're in the limelight, honey. You're
but
big news.
Idiot right here. He sees me every day. Why is he so fascinated?
Four burgers, anybody would be fascinated. Oh,
I got to admit, I got a little fascinated.
Just
I said, Robin's eating four burgers? He goes, yeah.
Well, let me show them to you. Since
All right,
so
let me see your burgers. I mean, that is Ganji in her face.
So, how did it feel when they talked about your four burgers?
Isn't it great? Four Big Macs.
And isn't it great when Ganji has that... Let me see your burgers.
Now, Howard, that could be 3 days worth. So that I got a 12 in the last 3 days.
Oh,
so,
look at that.
So how many are left?
What do you eat them, Robin? What do you eat them, rare?
I eat them however they come.
They should cook them more. Burger, very dangerous. Mm. Burger meat has been tainted.
I know. I'm hoping that I get that disease.
So am I.
Get away from John.
It's ugly in here.
Wow.
Wouldn't you think it was a little peculiar if Gary eating four hamburgers a day?
Yeah, I might.
You didn't see Gary eating. You would have seen me eating them.
Ordering four burgers a day.
Burgers. Burgers.
And what scares me more, she brings them home and eats them for breakfast the next day.
Right.
So?
You're way too involved.
You don't have to eat. See, this is what
they
do.
He's way too involved.
They watch everything I do, and just because I'm doing it, it becomes bizarre.
Who is that?
It's Grillo, it's John, it's Gary. They're fascinated.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're fascinated with them.
We just discovered Gary's diet drink only, an hour ago.
Yeah. What was? Uh-oh.
Here we go. What's going on now?
What's the problem?
It's a weird thing, Robert. I'm not out to get you, but it's a weird thing. There's two sets of rules, one for us and one for you.
Right.
It's like we all do this to each other. Howard in his book writes that we're all his little Nazis. And you come in here during the commercials. Let's just put a camera here during the commercial and we'll see. Everybody, this one's doing that one. That one's doing this one. We all do this to each other. You're not singled out.
Gary, just calm yourself.
No, but you always act like you're singled out.
Calm yourself.
I'm calm.
You don't know. It's compounded with John constantly watching me.
But no, Robin, John constantly watches me.
It doesn't even have to do with anything that might go on the air. He's just, he talks about me when he's not here to people who have nothing to do with the show.
Yeah, but he doesn't.
Who doesn't?
And tells me that.
But everybody in the office does that about everybody. You always walk in and Grillo will be telling some story about something he saw at Jackie's house or something that he saw my wife.
Robin, let's face it. If Gary was ordering six burgers a day, you'd want to hear about it.
Yeah, right. And if John mentioned to you I was ordering six burgers a day, you'd be in here during the next commercial.
John knows I'm on the Atkins diet. John is just trying to make a big deal about nothing.
No, you brought him on the Atkins diet. That's a lot of burgers in a day.
No, it's not. It's all I can eat.
Well, there's other things you can eat, but I see you're trying to make it easy by just eating hamburgers.
Right.
But you know, you can have a steak, you can have a pork chop.
And I might do that later in the day. That's why I have extra burgers to bring to work.
But you'd be curious to find out, right?
If I was curious, I would ask.
Business.
You know, I'm interested in who she's stupping.
Well, you can feel glad I'm the only one who doesn't care about your burgers.
Oh, please.
I'm oddly unfascinated.
Yeah. No bun.
You tell me, Atkins, you can eat four burgers a day, but that's it?
No, you can have as much protein as you want.
You can eat as many burgers as you want.
Burgers, chicken, as much chicken.
You were on that. You didn't lose a pound.
I didn't lose a pound.
How could you lose a pound eating 12 burgers a day?
We were eating, John and I were eating bacon.
You tell me I could eat 12 burgers a day?
You can have a bacon and cheese omelet for breakfast, a burger for lunch without the bun.
Okay.
And, you know,
as
no
many
carbs.
Burgers you want.
You know, say you have three burgers for lunch, but you can't have anything to go with it.
You cannot eat three burgers. You can only eat until you are full.
I never know when that is.
You're not supposed to stuff yourself.
No, but
you're not supposed to.
And I wasn't eating three burgers. But say you have two burgers for lunch, and then maybe for dinner you can have a steak.
Yeah.
And that sounds like a party. Until you
I have to have some sort of bread.
You can't have any pizza. You can't have any french fries. You can't have any carbs of any kind.
Well, only
french
fries.
No diet allows you french fries.
Well, I mean, but anything.
You eat every piece of garbage. I say any diet is, if a diet makes you crazy, you can't be right.
Well, this diet has prevented me from being crazy.
Really?
I'm feeling very ill.
Yeah.
Yes.
What?
Diet is preventing it from going crazy.
If
diet,
just cursed on the air.
First time you cursed in 5 years.
Crazy, you maniac.
Are you still on that maggot? Wait, are you still on that magic formula you used to have in the back?
What magic formula?
You mean that little thing you used to drink, that concoction?
Now what's he talking about?
No, I'm not lying.
I can tell you know exactly what he's talking about.
No, what is it?
You used to have this
little magic concoction.
You used to have this little concoction in these clear bottles that you used to take every day.
No, those are homeopathic remedies.
Okay, what the hell are they for?
What do you care?
Listen to him.
He's so into it.
It's like a laboratory back there, Howard.
She's trying new things. She's open-minded. Listen, you're fat as a cow. I don't know. You better try a few things.
Screw it.
You don't care.
No, I don't care.
You don't care.
But let me just ask, what were the homeopathic stuff for?
Various things.
Like what?
Let's see. Sometimes when I'm having problems with my throat, that's when you'll see me bring them to work and I'll drink them during the show. Yes.
And what else? Because there was three different reasons.
No, there's several different ones. I take so that I don't get a cold or I don't get a sore throat. Yeah.
This goes on all day between these two.
This is how scrutinized I am.
You can't. You're cracking from it. You're saying.
No, I'm not cracking at all. I'll just curse.
Scrutinized.
Two of you consume with one another.
I'm not bothered with him
really?
At all, except that he's constantly needling me.
Evaluating.
Why are you doing this? Why can't? What is that?
He's
Where
interested
are you going?
In you. He wants to learn. Yeah. You're up to a lot of exciting things, I guess.
She always gets mad about that too. I ask her, you know, who she taking to different various events that she goes to.
Right.
But you'd be curious to find out, right?
If I was curious, I would ask.
Business.
I don't even know where she goes.
You know, I'm interested in who she's stupping.
Why? Why are you so consumed with her?
It really is crazy.
So you ask, and what
so
does
I
she
I ask,
do?
And she goes, stop yelling, asking me about it. Just leave me alone. What's the matter with you people?
Give me a burger.
This is what I have to put up with.
Right.
Constant questions.
She's fascinating. Anyway.
Right.
You see, I am. I told you I'm fascinating.
Listen, I think eating is disgusting on all levels.
Whatever you're
And
eating.
I take no enjoyment from it, and I wish I didn't have to do it. But I do. And it's obvious to me.
I'm sorry that what I want to eat does not coincide with what you think I should be eating.
I'm not. I just offered the information. I didn't say anything. Right. I didn't editorialize it.
How many burgers did you order today?
For Robin?
Right.
Four.
Four.
Four burgers.
And two were eaten, Robin?
No.
One.
None were eaten.
No burgers have been eaten.
Not yet.
All right, now everybody knows.
But you can't eat.
Now it's out in the open.
I'm a mind reader.
I'm not saying that.
I'm going to give you a job.
I know.
You can report the burger count each day, okay? That'll give you something to do now.
You got it.
Well, will it be eaten or bought?
How many bought? We don't care how many were eaten.
Well, that's exactly. Four a day so far. In the last 3 days, four a day.
All right. If it changes, please alert us.
You got it.
All right?
105 IQ.
What's his IQ?
I'm in 35.
It's insane that I have to listen to this.
136.
Yeah, if you took it twice.
I'm just
take the bat.
I'm exhausted.
I am too. I'm really tired. I feel I've done my job, and I got that idiot out there with the burgers. I mean, really, it's fascinating, but I gotta get the show over with.
He strips him.
He strips it. He strip yeah. mines with those teeth of his.
He skins the nut.
Gorilla comes running in here during the commercials talking about, evidently there's a big box of donuts out there today, chocolate donuts and chocolate bars, and Gary has literally every minute, every time he walks by, takes a huge hunk of a chocolate donut and shoves it in his mouth. Hey, Gorilla, tell me everything you told me. I don't care if Gary gets mad. So funny. Here's the donuts. You just got to hear this story, then we'll do the news.
All right, the donuts and the candy.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel really bad, but I was sitting next to the box of donuts all morning, and he can't walk past the box of donuts without shoving something in his mouth.
He's getting so fat. And then, you know what kills me about him?
What are they doing there?
What kills me about him is he drinks all those slim drinks and
Success
and the diet drinks. He can't walk by this box of donuts without eating them.
And now we have chocolate balls here, too. That's what really got me. And I'm doing it because it kind of scares me, because it's really obsessive how he goes by, and he'll go out of the office, stop, come back in, grab a piece of donut, and then go. And then come back in.
What, does he take a half at a time?
Yeah. And then he'll come back in, grab a chocolate ball. And it's really, he
alternates.
How many were in there when he started?
I don't know. When I opened up the chocolate balls this morning, there was a whole bunch, and there's only a couple.
How does he eat a chocolate ball?
He doesn't just, there's macadamians in there, and I guess he doesn't like it. And you have to see him eat it. It's, you really, I mean,
Gary, what does he do? He chomps on the chocolate with his front teeth?
Yeah.
Until
the ball, the show me how comes
you,
out?
Gary, show me how you eat a chocolate ball. I mean, you've been eating them all morning, now all of a sudden.
I've only had one chocolate ball this morning. The donuts are what
he's lying?
You had at least three chocolate balls this morning.
Two, maybe.
Look, he's got powder on his face.
I've been eating
powder all over your face. What's going on with you? You're out of control. Are you having a problem?
No kidding. Yeah, I have a problem.
But why are you drinking slim drinks and stuff?
I am not drinking that. That was been in the refrigerator for months.
Oh, I thought you were doing some kind of diet. No?
There's no diet.
The powdered donut diet.
You're the biggest you've ever been.
Yeah.
He's put on 30 pounds in a month.
Wow.
He's
going
for a record. Come on. He's going for his personal best.
It is impossible to put on 30 pounds in a month.
But man, you eat such junk.
I know.
You know how you like always have phlegm and you're coughing and sneezing all the time?
Right.
I would suggest to you, I know you keep saying it's your allergies.
Yeah, but Howard, do you think I want to be fat?
No. But I'm saying all that coughing. He was in here sneezing today and coughing again.
Right, but
clearing the throat.
But Howard, if I could help it, I mean, come on, give me a break.
Do you exercise, Gary?
Not anymore. I haven't in about two or three months.
But so you want to be fat then? You're eating chocolate.
Ralph, shut up.
Exercise.
I'm sick of
you.
When did you become the exercise expert? You don't know whether I want to be fat. What are you, Ralph the psychiatrist? Shut up. Nobody cares what you think. You're not qualified to say anything.
Gary, you just said you don't want to be fat, but you're sitting eating chocolate balls and donuts. What do you think's going to happen?
Right. I can't stop eating. It doesn't mean I want. It's not like I'm saying I want to be fat. I wish I could.
Well, you are saying. You want to be fat.
No, that's Ralph saying I'm saying I want to be fat.
You don't think you're saying you want to be fat by eating chocolate donuts and chocolate balls?
No, because I wish I wasn't eating them.
Why don't you stop?
Because it's hard. It's hard to stop.
So you want to be fat. You know the consequences. You're going to be fat.
Does an alcoholic want to drink?
So what does he do? How many donuts is he eating?
I would have to say at least three.
And what do you say about chapstick?
Oh, he put chapstick on, and he's been eating the powdered donuts, and it keeps sticking to the chapstick.
Right.
And I tell him like twice, you got powdered donuts all over.
Well, why don't you do the guy a favor and hide this stuff from him?
Tom buys him and puts him on the desk for all the interns.
Oh, Tom is killing our Gary.
That's very nice of him. But that's nice of him.
I don't blame Tom. Thanks, Tom. I don't blame Tom.
Tom's an enabler.
He
enables idiots to act like idiots.
It's my inability to have any willpower.
Gary, let me ask you a question.
And why keep? Yeah, go ahead.
If there was like a bowl of carrots there, would you eat that?
I don't like carrots.
Well, is there anything? But if it was something healthy, is it just that you want the junk food?
I mean, the junk food is much better to eat. Yeah.
But if it was, you'd eat
maybe you should eat hamburgers.
Oh boy,
Robin's on hamburgers. She's losing weight like crazy.
I can't go down that road.
Really?
He's tried.
All I know is that John asked Robin. John came to me and said, "Listen, I have to order breakfast, but I don't know what to do. Should I go and talk to Robin?" I said, "Come on, let's be adults. Just go ask Robin what she wants for breakfast."
Yeah.
John said he walked in and she's like, "I don't need you to order for me anymore."
I didn't say anything like that. I said, "No, I'm taking you out of the loop."
Yeah.
Wow, you thought about this?
An evil loop.
Take you out of the loop. How are you getting your burgers?
I didn't need them today. I'll get them from him when I need them.
Who are you going to ask to get your burgers?
I'll ask him.
John.
Yeah.
I see.
I'm
okay.
Just razzing him.
I hear you. Man, you shouldn't keep those chocolates by the door.
And Gary, listen to me. But haven't I even tried to help you? Like, I brought you protein drinks and chocolate.
Yeah, you brought me a protein drink.
Yeah, so that's nice. I was the nice thing to know. I don't know why you have this, like, you blow up at me. Like, because like anybody else can razz you or do stuff or just make a joke. And you don't, when I say something to you, take it personally.
Because
like,
it's always vindictive when it comes from you.
It's not, just, you
and
take
I'm not,
it that
and I'm
way.
Not the only one.
You take it that
But I'm not
way.
The only one who feels that way about you.
But, well, whatever.
Grillo, John, everybody in the E-Crew. There's something in the way you say it that makes it wrong and insulting.
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
Hey, listen, you guys.
Wait, you want to see Gary eat a chocolate ball?
Yeah, let me see you eat a chocolate ball. How do you do it? You don't like the nuts inside?
I don't like the macadamia nuts.
So you take your big front choppers?
I already know how stupid this looks. And I haven't.
Because Carrillo says people want to throw up.
Me and John.
But, oh, there he is. Oh, he eats.
Oh. No fry.
He like strips them.
He strips it. He strip mines with those teeth of his.
He skins the nut of the chocolate.
Fighting it with the lips and everything.
So you've been watching that all morning?
Me and John almost busted a gut in his face when he did that, and we had to walk away. Like nothing was wrong.
You don't like nuts? I love nuts.
There's a lot of calories in macadamias.
Macadamia nuts are great.
Got to start somewhere.
Right. Oh, yeah, he's cutting down.
I'm on a diet.
Dean, the intern, said that Gary took his shirt off in the office and his breasts were huge. So it was very bizarre.
I'm totally fat. I mean, it's nothing to deny.
So how are they eating that big? The donuts? He eats them one half at a time?
I eat them like a quarter at a time.
Really?
You break a piece
Let
off.
Let me see your breasts. Are they? Did they get that big? Let's see.
Wow.
Let me see. Wow, they've gotten very big.
Oh, wait a minute. When he drops those arms, you've got a nice cup size.
Push your arms together. Let me see if you can make a cleavage.
Stand up.
Wow. Stand up. I can't see them.
Pencil test.
Oh, Jesus, you got so fat. I remember you were in pretty good shape.
Nah, it's been a while since I've been in pretty good shape. It really has.
Ralph's looking at him with disgust.
Hey, what are you going to do, man?
It happens. You'll lose the weight. Stretch marks are going to be a bitch, though. All right, thank you. Get him another chocolate ball.
You know, it was F the FDA, man. FemFem was working really well.
You were doing great on FemFem.
I was down to 24 pounds less than I am right now.
I know.
Can you still get it on the black market or something?
I have some at home, but I'm not taking it. I care about my health that much.
Gary blames the government for his overweight.
Got to blame somebody.
Yeah, okay. Go ahead. Eat another chocolate ball and get out of here.
What?
Right,
who are you talking to? What are you gonna do?
That's crazy Robin.
That's what he does.
The alleged normal Robin.
Where are you going? What?
Right, call me
who are you talking to?
You know, Robin. If it was me, your ass would be right in there immediately to say what weird thing I was
wanting a hard turn.
But I would never question you the way you questioned me.
Well, as a good interviewer, usually you question.
No. That's why we have such great time with you on the air, because we get an improve on the air after I've observed something. Yeah. But you don't even know I'm observing.
I observe.
You? No.
I observed it, and it was what Genji, 10 minutes of good air?
Question,
you know, air time about her whipping down a hamburger.
Whipping down? You've never seen me eat one of these things.
That's it. Listen. I didn't go to bed and set my alarm. I don't know. What's going on with you guys? Who's banging who on your show?
Dominic, what happened with you at the diner the other day, this guy? Did you hear that phone call from the guy?
Yeah.
What was going on?
Well.
You want to talk about it?
Wow. Yeah, I will.
Talk about it.
I had the surgery.
Yeah, now he's finally revealing it. He had the surgery.
When?
He did it over the weekend. Last week.
So he's done. Okay, so not since I've seen him last. And he's at a diner?
Here's what kills me. Here's what kills me.
No, I had. No, you know what? You don't have to worry where I am. It doesn't matter. I'm not eating anything.
Well, you got to hear this one.
Dominic.
AJ, you got to hear this. So I said to Dominic. Dominic calls me up and says, I'm going in for the surgery.
What surgery? The stomach surgery.
What did you get, a band, resection, or what?
I had at Lenox Hill Hospital, Dr. Gurian, G-U-R-I-A-N. She's fabulous. Right. She gave the band, and I did it 12 days ago.
All right. So he does it. He says, swears to me, he goes,
You better not tell anyone, please. I'm just confiding in you. I'm doing this for my health, you know, because I've gotten heavy.
Well, I didn't want you to say it before I went in.
Oh, okay. So I'm keeping it quiet. Meanwhile, I'm getting calls.
He's told everybody else.
All of a sudden, Wayne Siegel's on the phone to me. He goes, hey, did you hear what Dominic did? I go, what did he do? He goes, he got his stomach, you know, stapled or whatever. So
no,
I go,
no. I didn't tell Wayne. He called the office.
Yeah.
And they thought he knew. I told very few people.
You're telling everyone.
Listen to me. His face is on the building of the swing line building. Of course he gets it. Very funny.
Of course he got stapled.
Yeah, how cool.
So anyway, Dominic.
Yeah?
What happened? You went, and then Dominic had a horrible situation where...
Carney Wilson surgery?
Yeah, Carney Wilson, the exact same thing.
Oh, my God.
So, can you imagine a thin Dominic? He's going to be impossible to deal with.
Because Sharon got the banding.
Yeah, this is the same broad who did Al Roker's operation.
Okay.
My boy's here. Go ahead.
And I have to tell you, she's about 37 years old. She's the most brilliant. The only
Is she a fan of AJ?
What's that? Who is she?
Will AJ bang her?
No, this is a wonderful lady. I never make a joke. She's just incredible.
Okay. Well, anyway, so Dominic goes in for the operation.
Yeah.
And I guess it usually takes about 45 minutes. Dominic's took 3 hours because
they couldn't even find his stomach.
They cut the muscle by accident because, you know, he's got so much blubber.
No. What happened was, at that moment, I was diabetic. Which, by the way, would you like to know my sugar 5 minutes ago till I called you?
Yeah.
100.
What does that mean?
Listen, Bill Molino called. Your table's ready for Friday, Dominic, by the way.
What'd you say?
Bill Molino called. Your table's ready for Friday.
Yeah, Bill Molino. He ain't going to Bill Molino.
He can't. Oh, I want to go out with Dominic now.
So I said to Dominic, I called him before the operation. I was concerned about the guy. I was worried.
Sure.
Because.
You mean you love me?
Well, what happened? They cut the muscle, right?
Oh.
What happened, Dominic?
Nah, there's nothing. Listen, went through the worst part of this? Leslie. She was there, and you know me, I'm an impossible person. And it was I was crystal.
Does the woman you're with like to watch or know about that surgery? That seems very masculine. I just thought...
All right, Dominic has a problem, AJ.
Right, he's got to do it. But let me ask something.
I fought him for it, but the woman knowing about it can't be hot.
Yeah, he's got a wife. What's he going to do?
Yeah, she's going to get suspicious when he loses 500 pounds.
AJ, some of us can have relationships with women that last.
Oh, yeah, I know. You're right. You know,
some of us.
Dominic, how many times have you been divorced?
Oh, true. Yeah, really.
3 times.
I think you and AJ are in the same boat.
Dominic's been divorced 3 times.
I hope you stay without a headboard.
Now, let me tell you that. It is a wonderful process.
Wait, let me tell the whole story.
Get AJ off.
I'm not hanging up.
AJ, let me interview him.
I'm not hanging up.
What, are you going to slap me?
I'll come to the building and light it on fire.
I tell you what. Hey, Dominic, would you hold on through the commercials because I got to take a break?
I'll call you back. Say goodbye to AJ.
Oh, you know what? You fat bastard.
All right, Dominic, call me right back.
I will. Bye-bye.
All right, bye. AJ.
Yeah,
I got to go do a commercial break.
I'm on Friday Night 6. I have a new show, Friday Night 6 on FX, starting this weekend.
All right. Fridays.
Friday Nights on FX.
I'm working again. I was going to stop robbing people with a ski mask, so watch it.
All right, thanks. Thanks, AJ.
I love you guys.
Bye, later. AJ.
Bye.
Yeah, well, I'll never get there. Yeah, I got a whole story for you about Dominic.
Yeah, because I want to know how, I mean, to cut the muscle. I thought they did this, like, laparoscopically or something.
No.
I didn't know they had to go make a whole incision.
No, they went in through his big fat belly.
Ooh.
But wait. I got to tell you the whole story.
All right.
Because I'm keeping it quiet. I'm not even telling you.
You never said you didn't breathe a word. I'm very disappointed.
No,
but that's
nice.
You always tell me. You know I won't talk.
You know I forgot.
Oh, you.
I swear, I'm so self-centered. All right, we're going to be back right after these words.
You know, maybe if it was 12 o'clock on a Friday night and I'd been partying all night, I might think it was pretty funny, but not early in the morning.
The Howard Stern Show.
We're 15 minutes away from Naked Daredevil.
Naked Daredevil.
15 minutes away from Naked Daredevil.
Naked Daredevil.
All right, Dominic.
Go ahead.
All right, now we can talk.
I have to hear everything.
Would you like to hear the whole thing?
Go ahead.
All right. I Leslie and I discussed this, and she was a little bit against it, but I wanted to have the surgery because I just was tired of being tired, actually. You know, the diabetes had gotten bad.
Yeah, even Artie says that, like, when he went to eat with Dominic, and Dominic loves to eat,
yeah.
That, like, Dominic would, like, like they went to get Italian ices together, and Dominic, it took him like 10 minutes to get out of his car.
Yeah.
And little kids were laughing at him.
I don't know about that, but it got out of hand.
Yeah, Artie basically said, you know, Artie's like a drunk who's telling another drunk, man, you got a problem.
Yeah, I mean.
I love Dominic, and I felt bad for him.
Tell the fried clam story.
I mean, when we ate, like, we're the same type of people, so we both ordered a lot of food, and we got ordered a fried clams, and there's like... You know, four clams they bring in. Dominic would have like three of them and give me the last ones. Hey, you finished it.
It was out of control.
But actually, I loved it.
Actually, you ate three. I ate one, but I'm not counting.
You know what? Dominic loves food, yeah. But has an obsession with it.
It's an addiction.
Yeah. Well, so what happened was I went and researched. Well, Leslie did. Leslie on the internet.
You were too
tired. Now, here's the extent of Dominic's research. He wants to get the stomach operation, so of course he sees Al Roker got it.
That's the research.
Yeah, that's the research.
Not true.
He wanted a famous surgeon.
Right.
I went to, as I said before, Dr. Curry and Dr. Roslin, who are at Lenox Hill Hospital. There's a 6-month wait, and I actually waited about 2 months, and I went in and.
Well, you had to have tests to make sure you qualify for it.
Yeah, I went through more tests than you can imagine. It was horrible.
And now, how come you didn't get your stomach stapled? How come you got a ring around your stomach?
I got the band because that's what I felt was best for me under the circumstances. And it is surgery. You go in, but it's done laparoscopically.
Laparoscopically, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, his research, he still can't say laparoscopically.
Well, you know, now you're supposed to the first meeting you go for. You go for what's like a lecture, and they sit you around a room. There's about 12, 15 people, and I'm telling you, I was the smallest buffalo there by far.
It's got to be a crowded room.
You're the runt of the litter.
We're all sitting around waiting for the doctor. So I look to the group.
Of course, Dominic thinks he's better than all the other fat people.
I do not. No, but I did make a joke.
I'm better than you.
I'm much more swell than you.
I don't need to be here.
I barely need this.
I said to the group, you know, while we're waiting, they could give us something for nacho. A little pretzel.
All right, so Dominic had said to me, I went to dinner with him over the weekend, and he said, I'm thinking about doing it, but he wasn't, like, real serious about it. I didn't know he'd gone this far about it.
Right, I told you. He had mentioned it some time ago, and I thought he was just kidding around.
Well, then he told me, he spoke to me, said,
I gotta go do it. He goes, it's out of control. My quality of life is down.
Right.
My diabetes, my blah, 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 blah.
Well, you know,
and I said,
I have a few friends in this world. We all know that, Leslie, my kids. And I call Howard up, and I tell him about it. He's very sweet, I have to tell you. He and Beth have been incredible to me since I've had the surgery. Calling the hot, really nice.
So I was going to send him a big bag of Fritos when he got out of surgery.
I was about to tell that. Let me tell him.
All right, go ahead.
So, you know, I figure, you know, he's going to send me something. It's going to be nice fruit. He'll send me something to, you know, just a little something maybe I can have.
Right.
He sends me a cake, man, of flowers.
Because he can't eat the cake.
It's gorgeous.
Oh, a flower cake. A real flower.
Yeah, real flower. I was going to send like a big pizza.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, you know, manja.
Manja.
But I figured that's, you know.
The night before the surgery, Leslie and I, we have to go to the city. So.
Were you scared?
Scared isn't the word. But what happens is.
Did you go out and have a big meal?
No.
Yes, he did.
Something better. No, you couldn't do that. I drove to 10 restaurants to wave goodbye.
The farewell tour.
What are you going to do about, like, El Molino and all those?
Well, you know, all of them.
Like, what can you...
Chris Classical, they're all... Well,
Bobby Vans, you get two for one.
I once went... when I was married, I was with my wife, and we walk into an Italian restaurant. Who's sitting there, Dominic? He goes, oh, join us. We sit down. He had already ordered, just for him and his wife.
And there was enough food for everybody.
There was sausages and like pasta dishes like you never saw. And I'm like, oh, my God, this guy was going to devour this all on his own.
Yeah.
And, of course, when I was sitting there eating, he suddenly lost his appetite. He goes, right. I'm really not hungry. But he brought it all home and ate it.
So the
you would never eat in front of me.
He's supposed to stay home 2 weeks. I went to work after 4 days, you know.
But wait a minute. You skipped the surgery. What happened?
Yeah, what happened?
Well, first of all, when we get there for the surgery, everyone's making comments, you know. Oh, look who's here, you know, with you. Well, boy. And I got a little nervous first because Leslie came in, and you know how, like, you hold the Bible? She had, like, five insurance policies in her hand.
No, what happened was it was evidently some complications where they cut into his fat.
It wasn't the doctor's fault.
But I didn't say it was their fault. You're big and fat.
If it's a laparoscope, you don't even make a big cut. What is it?
No, they make five little holes in your stomach to put the band in.
Uh-huh.
And because of the, I had not, now my sugar's normal. And the diabetes is under control. I'm off medication already.
Right.
Wow.
Which is amazing.
Because you don't eat.
Because you're in your whatever that the islands of Langerhans are getting a rest.
He was first of all, the doctor said it was like operating on a whale.
Please, I've seen these operations.
She thought that, she said it was it's easier to get a whale back into the ocean.
You know what they had to send out for a larger laparoscope because they couldn't get through.
Did the doctor see you naked?
Well, not only did she see me naked, but she's wonderful. I can't tell you how great these doctors are.
Did they have to shave you?
Yeah, they did.
They shaved your pubes?
No, but the last thing I said to her, making a joke, I said to her, you know, now that I've, after I, you know, was done with the surgery and you go back for checkup twice already, I said to her one day, you know, can you do a transplant for me? You know, a certain part of me I'd like to, you know.
Your penis.
So she said to me, oh, will you stop talking about that? When you lose all your weight, you won't look that small.
Oh.
She saw him. He's got nothing.
That's some doctor.
Oh, did that hurt?
Tell about the specialist they had to call in from SeaWorld.
Oh. Yeah, Benji, you write one more joke like that.
That wasn't Benji. All right, anyway, so
I was supposed to stay out of work 2 weeks. I went back here for 5 days.
But how did they make this mistake and cut something?
Listen, I have 15 lawyers. We have the largest divorce in criminal practice. Still in New York, and we're doing wonderful, of course. Now, let me ask a question.
What was that about?
And a plug?
I don't know. Anyway, so, okay.
Do a plug.
So, you know what? Probably was the operation went fine, but there had to be all this drama around Dominic. Right. We almost lost him.
Oh, is that what we're hearing?
Now, I want to ask you all, should I do something that's been offered to me? Ready?
What's that?
Bally's wants to train me.
Well, not now. You're not going to eat.
You got to recover. No. He will be a saggy mess if
he doesn't
work out. I
can start exercising in 12 days from now.
All right, let me ask you something.
Should I do it with Bally's?
So now that... Yeah, of course. So now that you've...
It's got to be the right number.
So now that you've gotten the stomach ring on...
Yes.
What... Like, have you eaten anything?
Yes.
What do you eat?
There's a process to the learning how to eat again, but the beginning of it is which I laughed at someone saw me coming from a diner. I went to a diner yesterday for breakfast just to kind of get the feeling. No, and I had scrambled eggs with cottage cheese, and I had 4 tablespoons, and I could not eat another bit.
Wow.
Can you imagine?
Oh my God, really?
And then you, like, what happens? Do you start to get nauseous?
You just can't eat anymore. You can't look at food.
Wow.
No.
And lunch
it's got to be awesome because if a fat slob like Al Roker could be skinny now, it must be nauseating to even look at food.
Now, lunch was a protein drink.
And who told you to eat that?
Sorry?
Who told you to eat a protein drink?
Well, you have a dietitian they give you.
Well, Dominic said to me, he goes, some people are so sick.
Oh, he's
that,
commenting
yeah,
on
yeah, the other thing that. They drink milkshakes to get around
the band. Well,
the band, and they gain weight.
Or sugar water.
Yeah.
Sugar water.
Imagine going through all that.
And drinking sugar water?
You could, no, I don't. But people who want to defeat this, let's say you really whacked. I mean, I've already lost a tremendous amount of weight because 10 days before the diet, I had to go on almost a protein fast.
So how much have you lost so far?
Well, I don't want to say.
Say it.
30 pounds.
Wow.
In
is that true?
How many days?
You'll see me Saturday, yeah.
30 pounds.
Yeah. Wow. I need it to go to the next size. Well, you know, I have a wardrobe.
That's a shock. You know what the shock is?
What?
That I'm seeing you Saturday. I have no plans to see you Saturday. What are you talking about?
That's Saturday. No plans for Saturday.
Yeah, good. I have many plans.
Oh, okay, then I won't see you.
For dinner, what? So you could eat your spoonful of cottage cheese?
That's going to be so much fun. You got to do it.
Let's bust your ring. Let's go out and eat a real meal.
Wait, so milkshakes can... Dominic, if you have a milkshake, it doesn't affect the ring? It'll just
No. Obviously, if a ring makes... from what this Dr. Currian explained to me, and she's explained... She, again, I'm in love with her. She's wonderful. She's great. you have to see people in the there that have had the surgery, like they're back for checkups, and you'll meet a guy and he'll shake your hand. He says, "Hey, I know you really like listening." And I say, "Oh, great, thank you." And he says, "I said, how much did you lose?" He says, "Well, I'm not sure, but I think it's 280 so far."
Wow!
And you'll look at this guy and he's absolutely normal.
Yeah, you can't wait, huh?
Well, how much does Dominic have to lose?
I hate this because I'm thin and I work so hard at it. I hate that people get a ring and they're allowed to. I like that there are fat people that have no self-control.
Well, could you imagine, and I'm not saying it's going to happen because maybe God won't allow it, but if it do, I get down to like 200 pounds.
Yeah.
With my hair and face.
Oh, then you're going to be a lover boy.
I'm still, you know what, Dominic, I'm still relying on the saggy skin for you.
Well, after surgery, I'll do that next.
Well, we'll see. Poor Leslie, now you're going to live for a while.
Oh, she was so hoping to be out of it.
She was almost done with you.
Leslie was wonderful. You want to speak to her? She was through it all.
No, I want to speak to you. Let's take a couple of phone calls.
How much does he have to lose? Like 200 or something?
I have to lose 70 pounds. I was 298. I'll admit it now.
You were more than 298.
I was not.
Oh, that's a lie. We wager you over 300.
Here you go. Ready? Leslie, how
much do you weigh now?
He weighed 290. He should only have weighed 290.
Howard, yeah. Most guys won't do this surgery unless you're at least 100 pounds overweight. You have to be really obese.
Right.
That's not true anymore. They're saying now they've lowered it to 75.
Really?
Yeah, it's becoming a big thing.
He's about 100 pounds overweight.
Yeah.
He's about 100 pounds overweight, you think?
I wonder what it's going to be like married to a thin Dominic.
She only loved the fat one.
Yeah. That could be.
You think he could love a thin Dominic?
I love the fat Dominic.
Now maybe you'll hate the thin Dominic.
Yeah, you might not like him.
You know, Dominic's right, too. He's got a beautiful head of hair.
He does have nice hair.
He really does. Dominic thinks that he's going to be, he's going to be thin and he's going to be gorgeous.
Probably, he never told me he was overweight.
Because we've always said for years, gee, if Dominic lost weight, he'd probably be handsome. Meanwhile, we're going to see, he's going to get skinny, he's going to look bizarre.
Yeah, but that's something you say to fat people to make them feel better.
Right.
You have a beautiful face.
Well, my mother will say to me, if you were only like 150, you'd really be good looking.
You remember being 150. You were still ugly, right?
Yeah, well, I was 150. I remember the ninth grade. I didn't have broads dropping all over me then.
Dominic thinks he's going to be Antonio Banderas.
He's going to be in the movie.
Yeah. Leslie, let me speak to that formerly fat person.
Formerly fat
Has he really lost 30 pounds?
He's lost a lot of weight.
Does he look better?
Yeah, he looks well, actually.
Is he moving better? Everything better?
Did he bang you?
We'll see.
Is he able to bang you without Viagra now?
Oh.
Let's take a couple of phone calls for Dominic. Everyone's suddenly interested in you. Joe, go ahead.
You're in that much need of a ring. Why don't you go get a Prince Albert?
Okay. Whatever that means. Russ, go ahead.
How you doing, Howard? I'm wondering if any of these restaurants he normally went to are going to file for Chapter 11.
Probably, yeah.
I don't know if you noticed, but the stock market, Krispy Kreme, got 3 points.
Andy, go ahead.
What's up, Howard? I don't understand why this guy can't do it the right way, but hey, Dominic. Yeah. You look like one of them people that got caught like in a tiny little inner tube when you jump through it. It's stuck around your waist. You can't get it off.
Well, not anymore.
No.
He's going to...
No.
You know, he's going to...
No, the loss, actually, the weight comes off almost all over your body equally, but you asked an interesting question about, all my life I've been to every place you could think of, and I'm being serious. I've been to Duke, I went to Weight Watchers, I used to take amphetamines when I was young.
Wow.
And I'm like every other, two-thirds of America is now overweight. And the tragedy of it all is that everyone says, Howard says, it's willpower, emotion.
Yes.
But it's not true. I've been to psychiatrists, and how come when I went on Fenfen and I took that, I lost 60 pounds, I used to be perfect on my diet. That didn't make my father love me more or my mother love me more.
No. But here's the point. Food gives you an emotional high.
Yeah, you got something out of it.
It was your lover. And let me tell you something. You still have not resolved the issues that you have around food.
You got a band.
And other things. You got a band that's going to control you. And it's kind of sad because really what I worry about with people who get this band is that when they go and they lose the weight, and then they want to exercise and have the energy to do things. They can't even eat enough food to fuel themselves.
After 3 weeks, I start to go on one type of plan,
and then after 3 months, supposed to lose 10 to 12 pounds a month until your normal weight. And then you're eating like a regular person, but...
You could have done it. You could have taught yourself not to eat, but...
No, you know what?
I don't think Dominic could, because you don't understand the forces that were pulling at him.
Well, because...
It was physiological at this point.
Listen, right. Remember when he didn't believe in psychiatry? And
none of it.
Remember when he didn't believe you could have a drink, you can't drink, and you're weak if you drink? It's where he is at the moment.
Absolutely. Just because he can do it doesn't mean everybody.
And by the way, starving himself the way he does and
starving myself. I eat plenty. I eat five times a day.
Everybody sees Howard eat. Howard looks like an eating machine.
I eat tons. No. I just don't eat all the crap you eat.
No. Howard, your mom and dad are not overweight. My mother died of diabetes at the age of 70.
Wow,
yourself.
What's the point of that?
All right, so now so what does that mean? You should have not eaten. You should have been turned off to eat.
No, because I believe it's what's called a preset weight. And it's not because I'm weak or I get up early as you do, go to work all day long, built this business, successful as I am, and I needed something that controlled me, and I'm very happy I did it. And
Ross,
are you happy I did it?
Ross, go ahead.
Your other friend, Ross.
I want to know, what's the difference between between what Dominic got with the ring and what's the difference between the gastro bypass?
Very good. There's three things that can be done, and I don't mean to speak for Dr. Curry and yet to call her. But there is the gastric bypass, which is they take away part of your stomach. There is the ring, where they put a ring around you, and you make it tighter and tighter, and it's only been approved for 2 years in the United States, but it's 700,000 have been done worldwide. And then there's the third type, where they cut half your stomach away. My thing is the least intrusive, but if it doesn't work for me, and so far it is, I will do the bypass.
Well, let me ask you something. You say they make it tighter and tighter.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that. How
do they do that?
There's what's called a porthole under your skin, and they add saline to it, which tightens it, and it makes the stomach again smaller as you lose more weight.
Wow.
And Leslie taught me all this.
Ellen, you're on the air. Ellen.
Yes.
You're on the air.
Oh, okay. Hi. Dominic?
Hello. Yes, Ellen.
I had open RNY about almost 3 years ago now.
Open RNY.
And I had the same gastric bypass surgery.
Okay.
And... You know, right now you're eating these tiny little bits and you can't eat anymore. And that's all great because, you know, everybody says we did it the easy way. Okay? It's not the easy way. What it is, it's a wonderful tool to help us later after we lose the weight to maintain and to live a healthier lifestyle. And it's very true what you just said before about the fact that, you know, they operate on our bodies, not on our minds.
Oh, please. If you guys are congratulating yourselves on losing weight with a ring around your stomach, I don't want to hear it.
How dare you?
What did you say, Howard?
I said, if you're congratulating yourself for losing weight with a stomach around, that doesn't require any willpower. They put a stomach ring around you.
Wait a minute.
Congratulate yourself if you lose weight the old-fashioned way by limiting your portions.
Yeah, but this is a tool to help us.
All right, but don't congratulate yourself.
Okay, so I want them to keep walking around and leaning on the health system because they're so ill.
Yes, that's what I want. How much did you lose?
I've lost 140, and I've kept off 130.
That's great.
But it's only through, you know, now I have to really watch everything I eat. I eat like a normal person today.
Well, big deal.
Why are you that way?
What, Howard? You don't realize this is the same as a heroin addict getting off of heroin.
Thank you.
So what?
You're so much more human than him. I wish his mother would call him in and straighten him out.
Oh, please. You're kidding me. My mother could have straightened you out. You wouldn't need no ring around your stomach.
Exhibit your self-control.
I have to tell you.
I just can't wait to see you skinny.
Well,
that's going to be interesting.
Dominic will be running around in Speedos.
I mean, wonder if Dominic, and this will affect Dominic and Leslie's relationship, because she married this fat kind of guy.
Yeah, you know what? Dominic might become a playboy or something.
I'm predicting Dominic, divorce number four.
Yeah. In the working.
First of all, I've only been married three times, so if I got divorced four, that'd be difficult. And secondly, the most important thing was the diabetes got under control, because you know what? You could have seen me without legs.
Yeah.
How do you like that?
I would have thought that would be great. We would have had you on the show more.
A blind, legless dog.
Well, you know how great he could have been the new Beetlejuice.
That's one way to lose weight.
Who, me? What?
Howard, you would have liked me without my legs and blind.
Yes. Chauncey, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard. When we had that beauty contest, you know how much I weighed?
How much?
215. I was so humiliated
by that show that the next day I went out, I got jogging shoes, I jogged every morning, I changed my diet to chicken, fish, vegetables, and fruits. No junk, no fast food, no restaurants.
That's all.
I'm 180 now.
You look like Chauncey.
At the end of the day, you look like you.
3 months, 180.
It does make people mad.
I know.
When you do it the old-fashioned way, it makes me mad.
Chauncey, if I didn't have the operation, I could have looked like you. Thanks, I'd have the operation.
Joe, you're on the air.
Cool, steak for two. Dominic, you're fat and you're lazy. That's the problem. Look at Al Roker. The same thing with him. Fat and lazy. These people, they don't want to diet. They don't want to eat healthy. Right, Howard? What do? They go out to eat. They want to have steaks. They want to have mashed potatoes. They want to have all these heavy starch foods.
Man,
and then they get fat.
The other day I went to a restaurant. They served me salmon with mashed potatoes. I left the mashed potatoes there. It wasn't easy.
Right.
This gentleman on the phone talking. Can I ask you a question, sir?
Yes.
Your mother and father, are they heavy?
Nope.
Guess what? That you'll never be heavy. You don't even have
to... blaming your mother and father?
Oh, it's...
What does that have to do with it? Disposition thing.
Oh, please.
Really, Dominic, you can have the choice to take care of yourself. You choose to sit home and eat whatever you want, have all these desserts, and go out and... steak for two for one! Steak for two for one!
My friend, I have more willpower. I get up earlier, work harder than you ever will. And the choice was... It is something that is so strong... And
I'm proud of you, Dominic. Example. I know what you were going through.
Thank you, Robin. I love you.
I'm not proud of him. Joe, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, can I have the extra part of Dominic's stomach to line my pool with?
Yes.
That's very nice.
I'm putting that on eBay. Yeah. Let's go to Jeremy, who wants to say something to Dominic. Go ahead, Jeremy.
Hey, Dominic, I got no respect for this. When I came out of college, I was 5'6", 230 pounds, and I woke up one morning, I said, I don't want to be fat anymore. So I got on the treadmill, and I ran and ran and ran. And 6 years later, 7 pounds, and it's through hard work, not through some stupid surgery.
There you go.
That's all I have to say about that.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Do you have a full head of hair?
I'm losing a little bit of it, but I...
You're lucky because you probably have extra testosterone.
Whatever.
All right.
Can I ask you a question? Were your parents fat?
Yes, my mother was very overweight.
Was your mother fat?
You know what, though? Dominic didn't answer the question I had before about... What? I'm real curious. That's interesting to me about milkshakes. You get the surgery, you have milkshakes, and you can still get weight and not get full.
No, well, Artie, what I was suggesting is there's a way to beat the surgery if you want to destroy yourself. Obviously, if you drink enough sugar water, you'll have the calories will be such that you'll get under... You'll be beyond what you should be using in your body.
I think that'd be some awfully heavy sugar water.
I bet you Dominic figures out how to beat the system.
I hope not.
No, they tell you about this. You know, I love you so dearly, Howard, for all these years. And Robin,
Dominic is going to be back at El Molino. I know it.
Please don't say that.
You know, I'm going to inject the spaghetti into my veins.
Right into my veins.
Off the air, you're so gentle and caring. What's the matter with you?
Because why bother doing it off the air? I got to get paid on the air. Stupid. All right, listen, Dominic, I'm happy for you. I hope you live a long life. I hope you're a surgeon. I can't wait to see the before and after.
Yeah, but what's Dominic going to do now? He used to go out to dinner as a hobby.
Well, now I just sit at home and pick my eggs.
Do you dream about food or anything? Are you thinking about it?
Well, I'll tell you something really strange, and it's absolutely the truth. I dreamed of food the other night.
Yeah.
Isn't that strange?
No.
No.
I do that every night, and I'm still eating.
All right, Dominic, good luck. And there it is. He's coming out of the closet. Yeah. He had the surgery.
The only negative thing. I'll admit it. Is I am wearing a dress now.
How many? What's the prediction? Like, in how many months will we really start to see some real weight loss?
Oh, you'll see it if we see each other this weekend. But
he says 10 pounds a month.
It's
so.
10 to 12 pounds a month.
Wow.
Oh man. So in a couple
Until
of months, you'll really see it.
I should end up about 220.
What did you eat for dinner last night?
Last night I had a miso soup, M-I-S-O soup.
Wow, that's nothing.
That's
not even... Dominic wouldn't even order miso soup.
Dominic would have taken that and spilled it on the ground in the old days.
What is miso soup?
I don't want
it's
miso.
It's clear broth.
It's like chicken soup without the flavor.
Yeah.
It's like water, yellow pea water.
And I had for dessert a sugar-free ice pop. It was delicious.
Oh, you had dessert?
Still with the dessert.
Oh, you know what? He's going to be fat again.
You know it.
Sugar-free ice pop.
Well, you gotta have dessert.
If you're eating miso soup, you might as well just have the sugar-free ice pop.
Yeah, but
right.
You don't want to be rude. You want to have dessert with your guests.
Excuse me, but being the betting man that I am, would you all like to bet by January 1st?
Oh, no, I'm with this ring, all bets are off. I mean, this is not...
We're betting on a ring.
We're betting on a ring, not you.
If I can get a...
If we can remove the ring, I'll bet you'll be dead in a year.
If I can get an honest weight, an honest number that you are right now, I'll bet you to make it interesting.
Oh, I swear, I'll give you all the truth, because I'm now not embarrassed to say it. I mean, I know what I'll do. I started 298 and called my doctor up, Dr. Curran.
No way you were.
That's completely
I
naked.
I'm not going to lie to you. It was 298.
298, you weighed?
I admit it. And I'm 270 and a half this morning. And I'm going to put the scale away because it's too much to look at. I'm not interested. And by January 1st, I say I weigh 230 or less.
At what weight will you get separated from your wife?
I will never get separated. I'll get separated from you first for being so mean.
At what weight will you start dating?
Don't joke. I love Leslie.
We'll see. Here's my prediction. Forget about the weight. Let's bet on this.
Right. I'm not betting on
you're betting
married.
That this is going to be the ruin.
Dominic is divorced within 2 years.
No, really?
That's my prediction.
I'll bet you.
Fred, what do you
two
think?
2 years?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Absolutely.
2 years.
I'm too good.
Don't
to
take the bet. You're going to lose.
You know what? That's a very mean thing.
It's going to ruin his marriage.
And I want to hear you say you're sorry.
No. It's going to ruin your marriage. Poor
in
Leslie.
In 2 years, he'll say he's sorry.
Honey, I had you at a time when I needed you.
You know, Howard, this is the conversation 2 years from now. Mm-hmm. I got to tell you, at the time when you said it, I knew it was true.
But I didn't want
to want to think about it. But you know what? But I realized my eating was a sickness. My life is different now.
Now I'm healthy, and I need a new healthy relationship.
And now I realize a lot of my illness with eating was tied up in my relationships, and now I was
She was in love with the
enabling.
Old Dominic. I'm a different person.
And I don't know that she really loved me. She loved my father.
She loved
to
watch
me eat dessert. I more likely would say, how could I all these years let you tease me all the time?
Oh, and Howard, you lose, Dominic.
And Howard.
I have to break my relationship up with Howard, not Robin.
And Howard, you have to understand, my mother was fat.
Don't do that. You're getting me mad, you jealous little boy. You spoiled, jealous.
Here, wait. Here's Debbie. Debbie, tell us what happened. You had the surgery.
Yeah, I had the surgery, and so far I've lost like 140 pounds.
Congratulations.
And, husband is so insecure that I can't take it any. I just can't take the pressure from him anymore. I have to go. It's got to be done. We got to.
So you lost 140 pounds. Now you're getting divorced.
Yeah, because he can't take the insecurity. I think he was feeding me on purpose prior
right.
to. You know, he was always
that
like,
does
you know,
happen.
The jealousy is coming out.
He can't keep a job, but he sure can make me a sandwich, which was what I didn't need, you know?
All right, there you go, Dominic.
Debbie, can I ask you a question?
I hung up on her. Who needs it?
Oh, well, but you
how
know what?
Was your grandmother?
After
was your mother fat?
How much
your after 18 years, actually, of friendship with you, and someone who I've always felt loved me and I loved.
Oh, please.
Why can't you be happy that I have a chance?
I'm happy. I'm just, Robin wanted to make a bet. You want to bet on your weight. I want to bet on your marriage.
Dominic, I'm sorry. If you lose all that weight with that head of hair, you're going to start dating.
You want to make a bet with me, Dominic?
I am never going to. Don't.
Ah, so now you don't want to bet. You're willing to bet on the ring. I'm betting on you.
How about we bet on my relationship against yours with Beth?
Okay, fine. But here's the thing. I haven't changed my life. You have. I'm not the one. I'm telling you, this is going to be very life altering.
It is.
And I'm saying it's not going to survive. Your marriage isn't going to survive. That's all.
How will you stop putting a counter? What's the matter with you?
So then bet me. Then give me a bet.
You want to know the real truth?
Give me a bet.
What is the truth?
I'm going to tell you the real truth. The real truth.
Give me a bet.
Is that you?
I'm gay.
The real.
How much you want to bet, Robin? Since he won't take action.
No, the real truth.
I'll bet you. $500, Dominic will
got
still
it.
Be married.
2 years. What's today's date?
Can I take that action?
Today is the what of July?
29th
of July.
Okay.
Can I get
you're on. That? 500. Fred, you want?
I want a 500 on.
All right, another 500. I'm going to make a lot of money. Dominic, if you leave your wife, I'm killing you, so you won't see.
Pay me now.
If he leaves me, I'll be suing him.
Leslie. Be prepared. Be very prepared for the new Dominic.
I think the relationship that changes where both spouses are heavy and then one loses a lot of weight and then the other person
Well, you can
heavy.
Hope.
Let me ask you something.
Right?
I mean, I'm telling you, you're going to become more and more suspicious of Dominic as he loses the weight.
Dominic is going to start getting attention from people. Like
that's
never
right.
I'm going to buy a porch speedster.
I'm hoping
it doesn't happen. I'm hoping he can withstand the pressure.
Unless he get out now.
Dominic's going to lose 130 pounds in a house.
See, I'm trying to decide whether
the relationship has improved. I mean, look at all the money that's freed up for me to go shopping instead of
there
a
you
restaurant.
Go.
Leslie, get out now.
Yeah. Get out.
But I'm telling you.
Howard, I'm trying to decide whether to
I'm
bet.
I'm looking for another 300 pounder.
Yeah, you need another big boy, yeah.
Do you, I mean, does
you know any big boy?
Are you excited, Leslie? I mean, because maybe Dominic will look normal?
Yeah, actually, I'm really excited. And, you know, I've lost weight because now there's no food in the house.
Right.
So I'm really happy.
Yeah, because Dominic used to schlep Leslie around to all these restaurants.
Go to all these dinners.
Yeah. I mean, you guys both know. I walk into a restaurant, I want to have fish and salad. And he's like, no, let's have lasagna, let's have the pasta, let's have this. And then I was gaining weight, so this is great for me, too.
You know, first of all, somebody called last week and said that, I don't know if this is true, John told me on the way in that Dominic was yelling at Leslie at a gas station.
Oh, yeah, that was true.
But
Dominic told me it was true.
I said, please, Snickers bars.
No, Leslie and Dominic were having some fight at a gas station. It was an argument, big deal.
But I don't know whether to bet on this or not, because seriously, Dominic just got divorced 3 years ago, so he had to give away a ton of money. Does Dominic
no, he didn't. He had a prenup.
Oh, he did. So yeah. Dominic's got enough money.
There's always money.
He can afford to get divorced again.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Then I'll take another
$500. All right. I trust you, Dominic.
Leslie, keep your eye on him. Please. I beg of you.
Yeah, well.
Let me tell you something. Between Dominic and Leslie, I like Leslie much better than Dominic.
Oh, she's a sweetheart.
I love her.
What's
I love
not
her.
To like?
I'm sorry to see her in so much pain. I'm sorry, Leslie.
Listen, we all make bad choices.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
I'd like to bet $500 that Dominic kills a guy on a dinghy in Sag Harbor.
Larry, what's up?
Oh, my God.
What's up?
How are you, God? Listen, Dominic, you're going to be dead in about 5 years. I'm serious. My friend had the same thing, and he died 5 years later.
Of
the surgery?
Of the surgery, yes. He was 425 pounds, and he just died a couple months ago, and he was about 150 pounds.
Yeah, but he looked great.
Yeah.
How do you die?
How did he die?
He died of cancer. They left a sponge in at first.
Oh, geez.
Then he had to go back and take it out. And then he had so much cancer throughout his body.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean Dominic would get cancer.
That doesn't give you cancer.
Right. Well, all I know is every time I see somebody have this operation, they die.
Really?
I'm serious.
Come on. Al Roker didn't die. And Carney Wilson? Will be. Sharon Osbourne got cancer.
Yeah, I knew about this a little bit. I heard rumblings of this yesterday.
Really?
And I know some information. But here's the article. Dominic was I don't know what the fuck happened to this guy. I haven't seen Dominic in a really, really long time.
None of us have.
Oh, Howard. Yeah. It looks like he has to do, Robert has to do a crisis intervention with that green drink. He blew up again.
I know someone who just saw him and said he was thin, so I don't know exactly what's going on. But it says here, attorney Dominic Barbara, who of course calls into our show, and this was on 1010 Wins this morning. I was in a dilemma because Dominic is a friend of the show, and I go, I don't know how much of this to read on the air. And then all of a sudden it was on 1010 Wins, and I said, well, forget it. It's all out.
Yeah, once it's out, you might as well do it.
It's a news day.
Yeah, so, you know, it was on 1010 Wins, and then you go, well, and then it said several times he's referred to as the bloated attorney.
Well, that's our term.
Yeah. They said on the Howard Stern show, he's referred to as the bloated attorney.
Oh, okay.
I just like that that's like his credit. Attorney Dominic Barber and his then-wife Leslie attend a party in New York City. Oh, I see. There's a picture. Okay. One of Long Island's most flamboyant matrimonial lawyers was arrested Tuesday on charges stemming from his own messy divorce after police said he approached his ex-wife in a Glen Cove bagel shop, violating an order of protection she holds against him. Dominic Barber, 64, the divorce and defense lawyer who helped make Long Island infamous by representing the likes of Joey Buttafuoco and Jessica Hahn.
Butta what?
Buttafuoco. Jessica, that's how you say it, if you're Italian.
I think it's Buttafuoco, if you're...
Buttafuoco. was charged with criminal contempt. Police say he violated the order of protection by sitting down with his ex-wife, Leslie, while she was having coffee at 10:30 in the morning on Sunday with a man at the Glen Cove Bagel Cafe.
Uh-oh.
He was released from jail and is scheduled to appear this morning in Glen Cove Court. Let's see if there's any other
details. Hey, Howard, you know who that man was?
Who?
It was a police officer. And he says, I demand my wife to be arrested for stalking me. And then later in the day, it turned around that they arrested him. That's what they said in Newsday.
Yeah, it's a weird story. It was like one
of
these.
Well, remember the last time they had a story, it was weird.
The story I heard was that Dominic called the cops because he has an order of protection against him.
He called him the cops on himself?
Yeah, he called the cops on himself to say he wanted to go to the bagel store and his wife might be there. So the cops escorted him down there. Which doesn't
Can
even make...
Can you imagine that you got to go for a bagel and you got to call the cops?
Yeah, so, but I don't even know if that's right. This is all hearsay. I wish the guy would call in, but I'm sure he's in no mood. Maybe he is. I don't know.
Well, he never calls in when he's in the news.
Right. But anyway, so he goes down there, and then I heard he was hassling her in front of the cops, so the cops arrested him.
Yeah.
he brought the cop down with him, and then the cops saw his behavior. That's what I heard. And then... I don't know. Maybe I heard it wrong.
Remember the bowl of spaghetti? We could never tell about
that.
Yeah, yeah. In the latest incident, Leslie Barber said Tuesday that she and a friend were sitting at the bagel shop when her ex-husband barged in with a police officer and demanded that she be arrested for stalking him.
Right.
This is it. Police did not arrest her after she complained. Police later arrested him.
That's even worse. You call the cops and they arrest you.
The friend of Leslie's, a private investigator named Jay Salpeter, confirmed the names are the best. Confirmed that account. Dominic Barber said his ex-wife indeed has been stalking him. I just want this to end, finally, after all these years. Oh, my God. But why is he going down to the bagel shop where his wife is?
I'm telling you. And she says, I'm concerned for his well-being. Looks like seems like he's out of control.
Well, I did everything in my power to end our relationship amicably. His actions have been increasingly irrational, she said. As his former wife, I'm concerned for his well-being. Well, that's nice.
Yeah.
I always like when a former wife's concerned for your well-being.
But you're arrested.
Yeah.
Well... I don't know if he's nuts or she's nuts or I don't know who's nuts in this. It sounds like he's nuts, according to this, but I'm sure Dominic has a whole rap about this.
But that's the beauty of the law. There's always another side.
Maybe no one's nuts. I don't know. I don't want to say. I don't know anything. You know, Dominic calls in and he makes a lot of good points. He seems pretty rational.
Yeah.
Well, I remember being caught in the last time they, you know, because they were divorcing and there was a problem.
Yeah.
And then they got back together after the divorce.
Yeah, like three times already.
And then, you know, like each time they have like issues. And at one point they were calling me, each of them calling me with their own stories and nothing matched.
Well, you know, it's, you know who else got caught up in that loop is Beth, my wife. She used to get calls from Leslie all the time.
Right.
And I guess like the second time around they got back together, like Beth finally said, listen, with what you're telling me, if you get back together with him, then there's something wrong here. I don't want to hear about it anymore.
Right.
I don't want to be in this loop.
Right.
And then they got back together, so Beth hasn't had contact with any of them.
Well, I haven't talked to them since this latest get back together either.
Yeah.
But the last time they were separating, they were both calling.
Yeah.
Was that after she threw the spaghetti at his head?
Yeah, that was after the spaghetti.
The spaghetti incident.
I don't know what happened there either.
It's weird. When Guns N' Roses put out that album, The Spaghetti Incident, I thought, what a dumb title. But evidently there are incidents with spaghetti. So I don't know. It was sort of weird. Bubba was annoying me. I had to hang up on him.
Oh, Bobo. You said Bubba.
No, Bobo. He was annoying me on that call. He just was... annoying me for some reason. He wasn't doing anything wrong. I just...
Okay, but at first you said... I was like, Bubba was annoying you. What did Bubba do?
Bobo. The guy on the phone, Bobo.
I know, but you said Bubba.
No, I said Bobo. It's that green drink. It's clogging up your room.
Now, meanwhile, I can't hear either.
I was going to drink that green drink. Been so sick.
You'd be well now.
Yep, I'd be a lot better. Wasting all my time. So anyway, that's the Dominic story. I don't know what's true. I don't know if she... it sounds...
Isn't it funny, though, that he's a divorce lawyer and his divorces are the messiest?
Yeah, and also it's kind of weird, too, that, you know, Dominic should be thinking about his reputation. He is a lawyer and, you know, that's not good.
They're both lawyers.
Right. And it seems to me the cop was just sitting there. And after evaluating the situation, he arrested Dominic. So that's he speaks favorably for Leslie, let's be honest. The cop is just, he's impartial. He's sitting there. And he's saying, wait a second. I don't know.
I don't know. Even if you are divorcing and you have orders against each other, if you go into the bagel shop, just go buy bagels.
By the way, what is this bagel shop? It must be fantastic.
That nobody can choose another bagel shop.
Yeah, like they both have to be there.
They're fighting over bagel shop custody.
I mean, Dominic knows where Leslie's going to be. Is it really that important to go to the bagel store in the morning and eat breakfast?
Plus, if you're calling the cops before you get there because you know she might be there.
Yeah. First of all, why didn't the cops say, then don't go?
Yeah.
Go to a different bagel store. And say, you know what, Fatso? Maybe bagels aren't that important. You know what?
Let's take a walk instead of the bagel.
Right. Get on that treadmill. Or how about, why don't you wait an hour and then go to the bagel store? And by the way, why do you know your wife's at the bagel store?
That's true, too.
Dominic's got some splaining to do. He's got to call us.
And the two of them not being able to get away from each other, that's awfully funny.
Yeah, well. She claims she's trying to get away.
But she goes back.
That's right. That's right. All I know is I want the name of this bagel store. I got to try these bagels.
Yeah, they don't name the bagel store, and this would be the greatest advertising
right,
ever.
How about this? Dominic's a wealthy guy.
Yes.
Okay. Here's a theory I have. These bagels are amazing, right?
Yes.
Okay. Dominic must have these bagels. How about hiring someone to pick up the bagels every week and bring them to the house, even every day? Rather than risk this order of protection being violated.
What do you think of that? That would be solving the problem.
Yeah. Hey, Mark, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, now. Hey, is Gary too busy playing solitaire to book Robert Downey Jr. for promotion on Iron Man 2?
You know, I saw Iron Man 2 yesterday. Were you there? You were there.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I didn't see you after. When did you run out?
I watched the whole thing, but I just stood up and I had to go home. I was really not feeling well. I was coughing, but I don't know. I didn't get the feeling she was evil in the sense that I think she's a girl who took up with a married guy. How much she realized how married he was, I don't know. But
it can happen to the best of us. You've slept with married people.
Yeah, you can get involved in this stuff.
I don't know if Fred slept with married people.
Well, he sleeps with his wife, yeah.
No, I meant other than who
he's
with.
Not to my knowledge.
And you've slept with married
people. And I've slept with married people.
Right. It happens.
But I think the only truth that you can come out of it is I think this was somebody who was just excited to be with a celebrity, and I think she was trying to experience that celebrity by having sex with him.
Even Barbara Walters has slept with a married man.
Yeah, I mean, it happens.
Yep. So, I don't know. I mean,
I've slept with a married people. I didn't sleep with a
lot. I think it's weird when people call in and go, well, gee, you're gullible. What, gullible about what? You know,
Think with your penis, that's why you're not mad at her or something.
I'm not mad at her. She slept with a married guy, and I feel bad for Sandra Bullock. I actually feel bad for him. I think he fucked up the best thing in his life.
I don't feel bad for him.
Well, I feel bad for anyone who's confused. I'm just a great humanitarian.
I really dislike it when confused people take you down with them.
Hey, by the way, let's get off that topic and let's move on because there's a couple of things going on. First of all, Dominic Barber, the lawyer who calls into our show all the time, we said earlier that he had been...
Mayday!
he was arrested and Gary tried to get him on the air. He wasn't prepared to go on the air. But... this was a weird story that we heard on 1010 Winds, and then I read it on the air. How would you sum that story up, Robin?
Well, Dominic called the cops because he said he needed to go to a bagel shop that his wife might be at.
And the wife had a restraining order against him. So the cops came and escorted him to the bagel shop, which is beyond my comprehension. I don't know
that cops should be doing that.
Yeah, well, when do cops have time for that? But okay, they were nice enough to go with him to the bagel shop. And supposedly, allegedly, while they were at the bagel shop...
He then sat down at the table with her.
And then the cops arrested Dominic. the cop he brought with him. And Dominic went to jail and I guess got arraigned. Is that the right way to put it?
Yeah.
I mean, he wasn't convicted. He just, I guess they
held
him.
He was just arrested because he had violated, I guess, some kind of order.
I just think it's funny, about 2 weeks ago we got a call from Dominic. And Dominic telling us how great things were.
Yeah, that they had worked everything out and he was all on the straight and narrow now and everything was great. Yeah.
Here's the call. Dominic Barber, you're on the air.
I called to say hello to everybody.
Hey, Dominic.
Hi, Dominic.
My journey has been an interesting one. You know, I'm 23, 24 years involved with all of you and I love you dearly. When Artie got sick, I joined a certain program and I've been doing very well with it. Leslie and I are on excellent terms. She's, we're not together, obviously. And life is good. Business is good.
You know, Beth asked me the other day, she said, have you heard from Dominic Barber?
Right,
said,
I've been
no.
wondering what's going on. So,
well, when Artie went through his tragedy, I decided to make some major changes in my life. And I've been successful.
No kidding.
Well, I'm glad it benefited somebody.
What kind of changes?
Well, just not to do anything that is damaging to my body, including sugar, alcohol, anything.
Wow, no drinking, huh?
Nope.
Wow, good for you.
Wow.
How long?
Are you? 134 days.
And did you get your weight down?
Yes, way down.
What kind of program?
I'm feeling well, I look well, and most of all, I miss you all very much.
Did you? When you say you went into a program, was it a...
I can't say what the name is because you're not allowed to.
I see.
But it's my practice has never been better. Leslie and our relationship, although not together, has never been better.
No, so you two are not together anymore as a couple?
No.
So you seeing anyone?
Well, I was for a while, and then I stopped that, too, because I really want to work on myself, and
good
I want to get in the right direction.
Excellent.
Wow, a grown-up Dominic. What are we going to do with that?
Well, we fell for that one, too, then.
We're gullible.
I never believed, by the way, I just want to go on record as saying I should have at the time, that the reason Dominic went into some program is because of Artie.
You didn't believe that?
No. I think he did it probably for his own reasons, but I think he likes to tie
in. You don't think it, see, much like the 9/11 confession I made, you're now questioning whether Dominic actually was influenced by Artie's situation.
Yeah, I don't think it had a damn thing to do with Artie.
So you don't believe me in 9/11 either?
No, I don't know. I think that thought crossed your mind that probably that you could not save yourself or move yourself fast enough if you were in an emergency situation. I believe that.
Because it sometimes happens that, you know, something close to you or a major event shakes you up.
Yeah, I don't believe that shook Dominic up at all. I really don't. But I believe he went into a program, but I believe it had absolutely no effect because...
Why is he in this trouble?
It sounds insane what was going
two
on.
2 weeks later.
But I do want to speak to him about it.
Well, he never talks to us when these things are going on.
No.
And he should.
He should. He should always talk to us. He will, though. He said he will call us. At some point, he will. So I'm waiting for that. Marianne from Brooklyn, go ahead. You're on the air.
Howard, count down to Beto any minute on the Today Show. She looks beautiful, and your dog is like sickly, adorable, chubby little. I want to pinch him. But listen, she's in the studio with Barbara and Laura Bush were there. I wonder if they made contact.
Yeah, it was weird. Beth said to me, I'm going to be on the Today Show, and it says, guess, Beth Ostrowski and, you know, Laura Bush.
And the mother, Miss Barbara Bush.
You know, it's like, she goes, but that's going to be weird.
Yeah.
I think they treated her very nice. She's a good girl, Beto. Howard, you didn't say when she was going to be on.
He was only there one day, really. Like 24 hours.
Right. Well, Dominic Barber's on the phone.
No, boy.
Dude, I'm reading about you in the paper.
Yeah. Can't you stay out of trouble?
Listen, all of this is a very unfortunate, stupid error on my part, like usual. Basically, I lost my temper. Why I lost my temper doesn't matter, but it was something having to do with someone in my family and someone saying something, and I reacted, you know, don't talk about me, my daughter, stuff like that. So it's all going to be nothing, and I'm going to still, of course, be a lawyer, and I'm not fighting with Leslie. And
did you get arrested over the weekend?
No, I'm not arrested.
For stalking?
People had to be called.
Well, I assume they're going to talk to me. I don't, you know, listen, I don't think it's a joke. The only thing I have to do with Italian stuff like this is I used to.
What happened to you?
Apparently, well, he was around Leslie, and then Leslie felt that she needed to report it to the police officer.
No, Robin, that's got nothing to do with that. That's something
else. No, this is something,
this something else?
The thing I read about him in the paper today, tell me if I got this right, Dominic. A client that you represented, by the way, you did a good job for him. You got him his kids back. But he felt that Dominic charged him $200,000 that he shouldn't have charged him. Well, this is what's in the paper.
Yeah, no, what happened?
Yeah, go ahead.
I charged him about $400,000.
Right.
The other lawyer got about $1 million. It was the front page of the Law Journal that I won custody for a man who hadn't seen his children in 5 years, and I ended up with custody. It was the longest trial in the history of family court, Suffolk County. And you know what? I called him. He called me. We had like.
Well, let me finish the story. Robin doesn't know what this is. So
why don't you read it?
Well, I mean, I'll give a summary, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
From what I understood, it was that so the guy gets on the phone. You get on the phone with the guy, and you said to him, "Look, man, You're gonna report this, and my grandfather is in the mafia, and this other dude, your godfather's in the mafia. You're gonna go over and visit him."
No. You're taking it way out of context.
Okay.
Let me. Can I say something, please?
If it's true, I need to be nicer to you.
Well,
we had no idea.
You should have been nicer to me a long time ago, but I weigh 204 pounds.
Everybody can get a weigh in.
It's like Weight Watchers.
I'll be on the air very soon. I'm going to come there.
Yeah, could you come in and explain yourself? Because I want to know what's going on with you.
I'd be happy to do that. Listen, all I want to do is marry this beautiful, wonderful girl.
How long have you known this girl?
Yeah, that's another thing. You're going off the deep end. You've been married four times already. This will be the fifth marriage.
No, third.
No, fifth.
Well,
you married Leslie twice.
Well, I was unfortunate, but Leslie, I want her to be happy. I want everyone to go be happy.
But why do you have to get married so quickly?
Dominic.
All right, I'll tell you why. I'm really going to tell you why, okay?
Yeah.
All right. And then you're going to think I'm insane, but I'll say it anyway. You should think I'm insane anyway, right?
I do.
Okay. She's 37 years old, never had children. I want to have more children. Robin, explain in the Bible the men lived as long as 900 years, 670 years.
What? All right, Dominic, look.
Oh, my God.
Seriously.
Here's what I'm going to do.
You got to calm down.
All right. You know what my focus has to be now? Get my law license back. My focus has to be to get my vitamin out. I'm meeting today with a guy named Bogan.
Vitamin?
Yeah,
and please don't tell people you're in business with me. Aside from talking on the radio, you don't represent me or anything. I never say that. All right. And if you're going to threaten people, don't leave a voicemail.
That's what
you fucking head.
Said.
Yeah, really.
I didn't actually threaten him. I lost my temper. You know what? This guy Ray Young and I, we're going to go out to dinner on Wednesday night. We made up. We're going to be crying again. I won his case.
It got
very out of hand. And more important is
you got to do is get your law degree back. Or whatever that is.
He's got to get his license.
You got to get that back and get back to doing do a serious job and have a nice life. Stop it.
I'm going to do that, but as important as doing that is, and I keep saying it, but it's really a thing I've become very passionate about. I'm very passionate about people being thin now. I'm very passionate. You know, I took the band out of my stomach.
All right, so that's good. And in other words, you're using willpower.
Yes, right. I want to be thin, and I want everyone to be thin if I can help them be that. And I'm going to have plastic surgery soon. I'm removing the tire I have to because it hangs down. And maybe a plastic surgeon will call in and want to do it for nothing because I'll give them a lot of publicity on the Howard Stern show.
Whoa, boy. Listen, take that band they took off your stomach and put it around your mouth.
Put it on your mouth.
Because you're getting yourself in a lot of trouble. Now, get back on the straight and narrow. Don't look for shortcuts.
Yeah, what happened to the finding religion thing?
Well, that got boring.
I went to church yesterday. I read the Bible at 3 this morning. You know, I only sleep 3 hours a night. You know what I don't do anymore?
You need more sleep.
If you could have Gary send me a Sirius radio, I'd like to listen to the show again.
All right. All right, Dominic. Take care.
I love you guys. Cheers. Thank you. I'm going to come in within a few days. Have a good day.
Very good. Dominic Barber, everybody. Thank you. Bye-bye. That's Dominic, the bloated attorney.
Oh, my goodness.
Ex-bloated attorney. But he's back. I see on the phone, I don't know if it's really him, he's in the news.
Who?
Dominic Barbara.
No.
What?
Hello, everybody.
Dominic, are you losing your mind?
Absolutely not. Let me tell you this. Number one.
May I inform my audience why you're in the paper first, before you go into it?
Yes, sir.
All right. From what I'm reading, again, you're involved with your ex-wife.
Right.
You're being accused of trying to shake her down for money. You could go to jail for a year. I don't know what's happening to you, but you've got to get a grip.
All right, let me explain one thing. Three things. First of all, the most important thing is I weigh 203 pounds.
No, the most important thing is that I would think, and this is very important, please don't say that Dominic's my lawyer. He's a guy who calls into the show.
That.
No, the news did.
I didn't say that.
The news did.
I never said anything about that. Here's what I said.
Makes me look silly.
Her and I said this. Here's what I said in court. I said to the judge, listen, judge, we are the biggest embarrassment that ever's been to two people. I've had her arrested 3 times. She's had me arrested twice. And you know what? I said, judge, all this has to end. And I said to the press, look, I forgive her. I'm with Christ. I know you think that's a joke, but I really am with God. And I said, let's end all this. I gave her $3.5 million almost. She didn't want to give me back $300,000 of my money. Forget it all. I want to end every problem. I want to go on with life and just.
All right, so let me guess what happened here. I'm going to guess what happened here. Maybe you'll deny it, but I have a feeling because of what happened to you losing your law license temporarily.
Yeah.
That money is tight, and that you said to yourself, hey, I gave her all this money in the divorce.
No.
I'll tell her I want some of my money back.
No.
And then you said, give me 10 grand, but then you started saying that she had sex with her boss and making all these claims.
None of my business. I know all the facts. I'm having a press conference maybe next week. If not, we're going to settle everything and be done. No, I didn't ask my money back.
Well, how do you know you can settle it? The prosecuting, the DA is saying they're going to prosecute you.
Well, you'll see. Everything will be worked out. I have a lawyer involved with it. I decided not to represent myself in this part of the matter. And it's going to go on. Listen, she made an allegation that I go to Ambiance to stalk her. I'm in Ambiance every day. They're my best friends. I go there every single day. She put in the papers. I stalked. It's all ridiculousness. But you know what? Really, Howard, you know, when I was accused of stealing escrow money, only one person came out and said, I know he didn't steal. You know who that was?
Who?
You.
Me?
On your radio show, yep. You said, I don't believe he stole a penny. Well, I never did steal a penny. I never did. You know, everyone wants to tell all these stories, and that's okay. My brand is the best known lawyer in New York State. Who cares? I just want to go on with my life. I want to be happy.
Well, then stop calling your ex-wife.
It's not that simple. When I sit with you soon, I am going to come in.
Don't say
it. It's not that simple.
I mean,
I can't just stop.
Listen, you've got to stay away from your. Listen to me, Dominic. You respect me. I know you do.
I love you.
You know I'm a common sense guy.
I don't love on the show Fred, but I love everyone else.
You don't love Fred?
Of course I do.
All right. Yeah. All right, he's trying to be funny. But look, here's the thing. Oh, he's at your
Fred
expense.
Lost. Yeah, he's upset with
right.
him.
What I'm saying
don't cry,
is this.
Fred.
Look, you can't bother this woman anymore. You got to get her out of your life. And by that I mean, let her live hers. You go live yours. Don't worry about who she's with. Don't worry about anything about her. Just do what you're doing.
I got engaged, which I'm not anymore, but I was engaged to this girl, Pamela.
She left you?
We mutually agreed. Listen, she wanted to have children. I can't have children of my age.
Right.
And even though I look 50 now, I'm 67 years old. It's a real number.
Right.
And she showed, it's in the post that I got engaged. The next day, she had me arrested. Listen, you know what? I want. I love her son so much, Scotty. That's her stepson. I miss him and I love him, and I just want everyone to have peace. And we're going to have it. It's the end is now. I just want to go on.
All right. So Dominic is making a statement, Robin, that he wants to go on.
And yes, and Robin, I want to speak to you up the ass about something about your health. Nothing.
Okay.
I just read some.
Oh, I can't, bet you can't wait for that, Robin.
Yeah, I'll be calling you. Sit by the phone.
Do you have pictures? Dominic? Do you have pictures of Robin having sex with anyone? And perhaps you could.
Listen, I had a tummy tuck done by Dr. Acker, and I will tell you this: I can see something now that I haven't seen in 30 years.
I hope it's the truth.
I'll tell you this, huge. Finally, I'm not smaller than you anymore. Wow.
All right. Listen,
love you all.
Did they put you in jail for...
No.
You did not go to jail?
I just got
away. All right.
I got out.
Try to get out of this mess you're in.
I will.
All right. Then go on and make things better for yourself.
All right. Tell Gary I'll be coming in soon, please.
All right. Bye. Very good. Thank you, Dominic. Dominic Barbara calling in. He's very much in the news. There's been several articles in the paper that his ex-wife had to call the cops. I said to him, stop being involved in this situation.
I thought that was done.
Robin, I don't know why everyone complicates their life so much. I'm an uncomplicated guy. Jim, go ahead and Raleigh. What do you have to say?
Well, Fred, you did great today, but Howard's still the smartest guy on the show.
All right. Well, I don't know about that. I mean, Fred, you saw his awesome ability to recall.
Matched up with the Jeopardy champ.
Robin, it was impressive, yes?
Incredible.
George, yes?
Indeed.
Fuck you, scumbags.
How much you been drinking today?
Drinking? I can drink all fucking day.
Yeah. You know who Sunset Thomas is?
No. I drink cock in the fucking morning.
She's a porn star.
What's porn star?
You got a porn star here.
Yeah, fucked up bitch.
No, she's good looking.
Yeah, right.
Oh.
She got a nice cock.
She got a nice cock, but fuck that shit up in a minute.
Would you suck cock?
I would suck cock. I eat pussy.
You love cock, right?
Pussy means cock, yeah.
I know. You love cock, right?
Yeah, pussy means cock.
Would you suck her cock?
I would suck Michelle's cock.
My wife's cock, you suck it?
Hell yeah.
You stick your dick in her cock?
Hell yeah.
You like that?
Hell yeah. Michelle, I love to stick my dick in right in your pussy, honey.
And your cock.
Right in your cock.
Hi, this is Sunset Thomas from the Kit Kat Guest Ranch in Carson City, Nevada. I'm here today for a fan to win a date with me, but he has to get Beetlejuice to be able to say a phrase. So let's see what's going to happen.
Now, what is a special date with Sunset Thomas?
Special date with me? Well, you know, we go into the limo, kind of play around, have a little fun, do whatever we feel like doing. Maybe go out and have some dinner and then go from there.
Now, you've always been a good guest on the show.
I love Howard. Howard's the best.
So there's a good chance that you'll be naked in the studio?
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
All right.
I hate clothes.
Hey, how's it going, man? I'm Double A. I'm back down here at the Howard Stern Show. I want to try and redeem myself. The last time I was here, I had human liquid water balloons thrown at my ass to meet The Rock. This time, I'm looking to grab me a piece of ass and win a date with porn star Sunset Thomas.
Now, what do you have to do to win the date?
I have no idea, man. I hope it's nowhere near as bad as those balloons, man. Still not living it down.
Now, why do you want to win the date?
Because I haven't got laid in a long time, and looking forward to it.
All right, let's get in our next feature so we don't get too far behind. Sunset Thomas, who is a porn star. She's got a new video out, Misty Beethoven.
Misty Beethoven. Now, that sounds familiar. Wasn't there once a movie called Misty Beethoven?
No.
With Charles Grodin.
That was Beethoven.
Oh, it was Beethoven.
And there was a movie called Misty.
Misty and Beethoven were two different movies.
It's time to play Beat the Juice. This is a fun game. So coming into the room right now is Beetlejuice, Sunset Thomas. Oh, Sunset looks great. Beautiful body. All done up. Great outfit, honey.
She's sparkling today.
Hi, Howard.
How you doing, sweetheart?
Hi, Robin. How you been?
Good.
Double A, how's that? Huh?
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
Sweet.
You'd like to win that, right?
Hey,
definitely.
He wants you real bad, Sunset Thomas, but he can't have you unless he beats the juice.
You got to beat the juice.
You got to beat the juice. Do you know how this works, Double A?
Hey!
No, not at all.
How are you, Double A? You were on TV with The Rock the other night.
Last night.
Did you watch?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Sunset, how you been, baby?
I've been good. I've been really busy.
You look better than ever.
Thank you.
Big boobies, nice flat stomach.
Healthier.
Unbelievable. Yeah, you look great. I can't believe you're a whore.
I know. But I love being a whore, though.
I know.
It's awesome.
It's awesome.
Actually, I'm no longer at the Bunny Ranch anymore. I'm at the Kit Kat Guest Ranch in Carson City.
What happened? Huh? Falling out?
Things happen.
Things happen. What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
Just had to go my own way, be my own woman, you
something
know?
Something must have happened.
Well, you know, she and the guy from the Bunny Ranch were a couple for a while.
Oh, yes.
Oh, so you broke up?
Yeah, I broke up with him.
Uh-huh, so they had to get out of there, huh?
I had to get out of there. Yeah. But I love the Kit Kat. The girls are just so beautiful there.
Double A is focused on you like a hawk.
I know, look at his eyes.
Man. When's the last time you got laid, Double A?
Oh, at least a year and a half, a year.
Yeah. But you have like hookers come to your house every day, right? Like, or every once a week?
Yeah, like massage girls, you know. You read the back of the paper, they have those ads in there, so
yeah.
I just call up a couple of those girls and come over.
What does that cost?
Like 120.
120 a week you spend on girls?
Yeah, definitely.
Are they hot?
Yeah. You know what I do is if I usually hang out in front of my house and like they'll pull up, and if they're not that good, I'll just, and they ask, is this the right house? I'll be like, I have no idea what you're talking about. If they're not hot, but if they're hot, just take them right in.
Right. Oh, I see. So this way you say, no,
yeah,
I
never. You save them money, yeah.
Right.
You
right.
exercise
that's good.
Some quality
exactly.
control.
Sounds like a foolproof plan.
Now, you wouldn't send Sunset Thomas over.
Oh, hell no. Smoking.
Smoking hot.
Here, you want to grab?
Oh, gotta be quiet. My mother's sleeping upstairs. Oh,
that's very nice. You're letting Double A feel you up. Isn't that sweet? You're very free with your body, aren't you?
Yeah.
Can I tie you up in one of my championship belts?
Sure, baby.
So Double A, so how's that work? So, like, the chick comes over. She comes over in a car once a week. You get a chick. And they give
and
you...
And it's always the pretense of a massage.
Uh-oh, here comes Beetlejuice. 1 second. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Beetlejuice.
He's taking his walk to the microphone.
What an entrance.
Hey, Beat. How's my brother from a different mother?
He's all right. He's
what?
Doing fine.
He's doing fine.
He's doing fine.
He's well, talking about himself in the third person now?
He's like Garth Brooks, right?
Donna.
Yeah. All right. So...
Yo, Howard.
Yeah.
Beat's becoming like a little difficult now. He's giving orders. He's you know, we're asking him to hurry up, and he's in the bathroom. He's taking his own time. I mean, he's like a star.
Don't rush him.
Yeah, he thinks he's like a big star. What's up with that, man?
Hey, because I'm a man. That's why.
Right.
I had to do what I had to do.
You're not going
to
be rushed by anyone.
No.
Not even KC or Howard Stern.
That's right.
Right. Wow. Wow. Well, Beat, let me get to you 1 second. Let's hear Double A's story, because Double A goes to massage girls once a week. They come to his house. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah, I hear you.
All right. Now, Double A, so the girls come to your house, and then they walk in, if you like, what they look like. What are you, already in your towel? You're ready for your massage?
I let them in, and then just go right to my room, and... Listen, I tell them all the time, we don't need no massage or anything like that. Let's just get right down to business.
Right. You don't want any kind of sensuality or anything like that. Right. Wow.
Get down to business.
Yeah. That ain't going to happen, brother.
With you and Double A?
No. I'm talking about the young lady right here.
Right. You like her, huh?
Oh, she's nice. Yeah.
So you have full sex with these girls, Double A, or do you have just like a massage kind of situation?
Some kind of release.
I love that.
Full sex?
Yes.
Yeah. Full sex.
Listen to Beetle.
All right. I think it's time to play.
The real man knows to do it. That.
All right. Well, let's play our game. Double A, you're a horny guy. You want Sunset Thomas.
In the worst way.
In the worst way. You'd really have fun with her, huh?
Oh, without a doubt.
Now, would you tell her no preliminaries, just let's get down to business?
Oh, I'll take my time with her.
Nice and slow.
Dude, you are so creepy and pervy. It's amazing. Never seen anything like it. Mm-hmm. You can't get a girlfriend in AA? I mean, just like some lady that you could be in a relationship with, you wouldn't have to pay for sex?
Nah.
No. You don't want to take a girl out on a date? Or?
Oh, I will, but they don't seem interested, so.
Nah, they're not too interested in you.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe it's that pervy sort of. Did you say he was real pervy with you, Artie?
Well, no, he was asking about that Party of Five chick. Why, are you into her? You're into her or something?
Oh, definitely, man. She's hot, too.
All right, AA, let's get down to the game and let's get to it. Behind your head is a clock. It's got 3 minutes on the clock.
Okay.
You have 3 minutes to get our friend Beetlejuice, superstar Beetlejuice, to repeat a simple sentence. Beetlejuice has to say the full sentence. You could teach it to him. And then all Beetlejuice has to do to help you out is repeat the sentence. Can't do it, and you can do it. You can teach it to him in stages, but he's got
to
repeat the full sentence,
the whole thing at once.
The question is, who's going to teach it to AA?
For example, if I said row, row, row your boat,
I'll
give you an example. Beetlejuice, if I was to say, repeat row, row, row your boat, could you do it?
Row your boat? Yeah, you can row your boat down the street, though.
All right, but do me a favor, because Beetlejuice, do me a favor, because I could win a big prize. Just say, row, row, row your boat.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Row your boat.
All right. You see, now that would be pretty good.
That isn't the exact sentence.
But it's close enough for my money.
All right.
I'm not going to be real harsh in my judgment.
Okay.
A row here and there, Robin.
You could throw in an extra row.
Yeah.
That's right. What is it, Baba Booey? It seems like you have something to say.
No, here's the paper with the phrase that he has to get him to say.
Don't hand it to him. Okay. Thank you.
Baba Booey.
All right.
Booey.
The phrase, are you ready?
Yeah.
And when you begin teaching Beetlejuice, the clock will go. You have 3 minutes to get him to say it. I was able to get Beat to say, row, row, row your boat. Right. The phrase is going to be, look at me, the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain. Simple phrase.
I say go home now at AA.
Do you understand that phrase, AA?
Say again.
Let me hear you say it.
You say one more time.
The rain in Spain, falls mainly on the plain.
Falls mainly on the plain.
Let me hear you repeat that.
The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain.
Okay.
Now, wow.
You talk to Beetlejuice. You calmly explain to him. I found that being calm works best with Beat. Am I right, Beat? You like people?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
He
How are you,
buddy?
He
only got 3 minutes.
Everything okay with you?
Oh, he only got 3 seconds.
All right. So you understand this game?
Right.
He's playing for Sunset Thomas.
That's right.
You want to help him out?
You want to help the brother out?
I'll help him out.
All right. Here we go. AA, the microphone is yours. You have 3 minutes starting now.
Beetlejuice, listen, look at me. The rain in Spain.
Rain in Spain?
Falls mainly on the plain.
Four main names on the plain.
No, Beetlejuice, listen. The rain in Spain.
Rain in Spain.
Falls
on the plain. Swells on the plain. No. I know.
The rain in Spain. Go ahead, you say we don't. The rain in Spain.
Rain in Spain.
Falls mainly on the plain.
All right. Go ahead, say the whole sentence, Pete, now.
Falls and rains, falls on and rains, plays on the plain.
Oh, boy.
You still got some work to do, AA.
You got lots of time, AA.
I still got it.
The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain.
Four rains, rain on the plain.
Can I make a recommendation?
Yeah.
Say the rain.
The rain.
I can say the rain falls on the rain.
Visual. The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain.
Four rains falls on the
plain.
All
right. Now I see you have under 2 minutes left.
You only got 2 minutes left.
I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to make it easy, AA.
I'm making it easy.
Get him to say the rain in Spain, and I'll give you the prize.
Okay. Listen, Beetlejuice, just say the rain in Spain.
Rain in Spain.
No, the rain in Spain.
Rain or Spain.
The rain in Spain.
Whatever you want to call it.
How about breaking it down, AA, to the rain?
The rain, Beetlejuice, the rain.
The rain or falls?
No. What? The rain in Spain.
Well, that's a, I can say that it rains
please,
in Spain.
Please, Beetlejuice, look at this hot girl. The rain in Spain.
In Spain.
But you gotta say the rain's
on Spain.
No,
right?
The rain in Spain.
Rain is for Spain.
The rain in
is
Spain.
For Spain.
No,
yeah.
the rain in Spain.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
All right, Beat, here's the chance.
All right,
Beat, you ready? This is for the chick and everything. He says the rain in Spain. Can you say it?
I say rain in Spain.
That's close.
The rain in Spain.
Rain in Spain.
The rain in Spain.
The rain in Spain.
He said it.
Yeah, but he's got to say it on his own.
Oh.
I can say it.
Go ahead,
the rain on Spain.
In Spain.
In Spain, yeah.
The rain in Spain. Say it all together.
All the rain in Spain.
No.
He said it.
The rain in Spain.
All rain for Spain.
Oh.
The rain in Spain.
10 seconds.
Well, a rain on Spain.
The rain in Spain.
The rain on Spain.
In Spain.
In Spain.
The rain in Spain.
The rain on Spain.
All right.
Right under the clock, you did.
Who's the man?
Beetle's the man.
Beetle's the man. Who's the man?
That's right. Beetle's the man.
Wow.
You beat the juice.
And by the way, as it turned three.
You never can.
Right under
that
the wire.
That was close.
Honey, wow. I feel bad for you. You got to go be with Double A.
I'm already in for the Double A.
That's all right. We're going to have fun. We're going to have fun in the limo, and then I'm also going to take him over to the cha-cha.
Okay. What's the cha-cha?
It's an Italian restaurant.
I want to go with you to the cha-cha. Forget him.
Oh, you love the cha-cha, huh?
Mm.
I love to play the cha-cha.
Now that he can say.
I made this all very...
I can say that in Spanish because I know the cha-cha is Spanish. Uh-huh.
I meant to say Double A, you get to F Beetle, not
I don't think it's going to work like that.
I'm just kidding, of course. Just making a joke. Well, Beetle, Sunset, you look fantastic. I cannot believe you're a whore. And I mean that with a compliment. I mean, you look unbelievable.
Thank you.
I don't know what they got to pay to have sex with you. I mean, it must be unbelievable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, hypothetically. Yeah, how
what's
much?
It cost to be with a chick like you?
I don't want to say prices over
there.
Oh,
come on,
baby.
You
got to come out and see.
It's a little legal. You do it legally. I mean, you do go to a place where it's legal.
Yeah, I'm at the Kit Kat, so.
Is it more than 1,000 to have sex with you?
Mm-hmm.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
I could see why.
More than 1,500?
But if you party with me for an hour, you can come as many times as you want.
I don't know if we can say that.
I didn't know.
You're saying...
I'm a cuss word.
I'm what's it cost to have... Like, is it over 1,500?
Yeah.
2 grand?
Mm-hmm.
So over 2 grand?
No.
It's around 2 grand.
Mm-hmm.
2 grand. Wow.
I don't
but I'll give you a party you'll never forget.
How many dudes you do a day?
I don't know, 7.
7 dudes times 2, that's like $10 million a day you make.
Mm-hmm.
You don't work every day, do you?
No. No. I actually go on the road. I feature dance and stuff like that, too.
Why bother feature dancing when you can make $14,000 a day?
Well, because I like going out and being out in the public for other fans to see me that can't really afford to come out and see me. So.
I see.
So it kind of helps out.
Are you a millionaire?
Huh?
You must be. If you're
I'm getting
making,
up there.
if you're making 14 grand a day, that's you got to be a millionaire.
Yeah, I'm actually in the process of right now. I'm going to have a couple of Sunset Thomas's Gentlemen Clubs.
Wow.
I'm in the workings in that. And then I also have Sunset Thomas's dance studio. I train dancers how to have more high energy on stage.
Hmm. So. How do you like that, Double A? That's your new girlfriend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She's an entrepreneur.
You want a date with her.
Very awesome. Sexual, too.
You know, Howard, I know guys who spend about 24 grand a year on golf trips to go away golfing.
Yeah.
Yes. For that same money... Forget golfing, you could bang her once a month.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's just, come on.
That's worth it.
About a hobby, I mean.
Right, Pete?
I'll clean their balls for them.
Oh.
Right on the golf course.
Yeah. Right on the golf course.
Let me take a couple of phone calls real quick. Double A, congratulations to you. Congratulations to Beetlejuice. Let's go to Billy. Billy, you're on the air.
Howard, I'm sorry about the line. I'm on a hardwire line. Hey, Double A, you got a lot of balls even coming out of your house. After that show last night.
Oh, yeah.
Stop giving him prizes, Howard.
Well, he did win. He won Sunset Thomas, and I got to tell you, it's a good prize.
That's You've awesome. Been giving him prizes forever, though. He goes to Vegas and everything, that little jerk-off.
Let's go to Brian. Brian, you're on the air.
Howard, I saw Sunset Thomas here in Baltimore at the Hustler Club making out with all sorts of guys. Every guy that came up to her
She was just making out with, she's such a little whore, and I love it.
I love
little
whores.
You love being a whore?
Oh, I love little whores. I loved her making out with guys. She was making out with me. I love it.
What is it? You just, like, you just go out there and make out with guys? And are you, like, what happened to you that you're so whacked out about sex? Like, I mean, it's, like, almost meaningless.
Well, you know, with some stars, you know, sometimes after you become such a big name, it's like, oh, don't touch me, don't this. Me, I'm just very friendly with my fans. Come up, give me a hug, grab my butt. I'm not going to freak out, wow. You know, grab my boobs. Well,
there
you
go. Do you ever get an STD, anything like that?
No, I mean, I use condoms.
You use condoms?
Like that, yeah.
You don't get any lice or anything?
No.
Lice.
No crabs,
no.
Nothing?
Lice.
I don't have sex with them when I'm on the road featuring it. They have to go to Kit Kat.
All right. Well, there's a girl, Beetle. You got to love her.
Oh, yeah. Trust me. I got some score.
Yeah. You got something for her, I bet. Oh, yes.
Is Sunset worried about the new problems in the industry?
Yes, I am, actually. It's funny you mention that.
Do you wear condoms? Do you have the guys wear condoms in your videos?
Yes, I do now.
You do now?
Yeah, I do now.
In the past, you haven't?
No, in the past, I haven't. But that's why I'm focusing more on my nightclubs and things like that. I'm going to venture off more into that. So.
Less porno, more whoring.
All right. Exactly.
Hey, Sunset, can we see your cans?
Sure.
Oh, wow. Oh, thank you. Wow.
I was beginning to wonder if you're going to ask.
Those are great.
Artie is always thinking.
Yeah, well, I'm, you know, someone's got to be on top of these things.
How do you like those, Beat?
Oh, that's fine with me.
Right. You like that, huh?
I love them.
Can we see your ass?
I got something
for
that ass.
No.
Why?
Normally, I have a spider bite.
You have a spider bite? Let me see.
Spider bite.
Come on. Where do you have a spider bite?
I got something more better than a skinny bite.
Oh, big deal.
Some John named Spider?
I'm not worried about that.
Right here. I got something for you.
Yes, Jimmy. Go ahead. We have Jimmy on the air. What's up, pal?
Yo, Sunset, you were good last night, baby.
Thank you, darling.
Were you with her last night?
Last night, Howard. She's insane, dude.
Were you with any guys last night?
No.
No, all right. All right, Sunset, good luck to you. Double A.
Congratulations.
Once again, thanks to the greatest show on earth, the Howard Stern Show.
And be
Thank
careful.
You, Beetlejuice. I'm going to have a gorgeous girl over here for
Be careful rubbing up against that spider bite. That's all I'm going to tell you.
I ain't going to rough you up.
I'm going to give her a few
Unless
bites of my own.
Unless you got something better.
There you go.
All right, Sunset, you have your man.
If you have something better with condoms, you better come up with something, buddy.
What is that
what
you're
is
holding?
Beetlejuice carrying on about?
Condom?
That's right,
condoms.
Buddy.
You carry condoms with
That's
you.
That's right.
You're ready.
You're playing it safe.
That's right. I'm ready to get on, brother.
All right. Good for you.
This woman, she wants it. Hey, we get it on.
Right. Good for you, Beat. All right. We're going to take a break, Robin. That's our first edition of Beat the Juice.
Yeah.
Where Double A beat the Juice, but it took him 3 minutes to do it.
It takes me three days.
What's that?
It takes me 3 days to do it.
Right.
Yeah, usually.
What do you mean usually? Well, honey, I'll take you on. How about that, Rob? I'll take you down. I'll bang you down harder. You ain't even know it's coming.
Right.
Hey, look out for the train, honey.
Good thing you have your condoms.
Man, look out for the train, because the man is coming through for you, honey.
All right, Beetle.
Well, you're right. The next time we'll play for 3 days straight. When we do the phrase, we'll do Beat the Juice for 3 days.
That's right.
Right, okay.
Days.
All right, we'll... I almost hate to hang out. There's so many of Beetlejuice's fans on
really?
The phone.
Really? Oh, we got to take one phone call.
John, you're a Beetlejuice fan?
No, I beat up Beetlejuice one time. He was mouthing off to my girl.
You're a chump.
Listen to me. I'm 6 foot
You're a
chump.
750
pounds. Why
don't you come out here and say that in my face, you chump?
Don't even tell me about Cookie Monster.
Why don't you come out here and say it in my face, chump? Why don't you come down? Why don't you come down? I'll beat the mess out of you. Come on down.
You know about me.
You're a chump.
I saw you with Big Bird.
You're a chump. You are a chump.
Cookie Crisp.
You are a chump.
Do you know anything about acting?
You are a chump.
What do you know about Merrick Park?
What do you know about a fighter, boy?
I was eating a pita with a gyro.
Better speak up, boy.
Oh, come on,
look up. Better look up to me and say it.
Oh, Espanol? You know Espanol?
You're a chump.
Oh, no, Bill Clinton.
You're a chump.
Bill Clinton.
You're a chump.
What do you know about Bill Clinton?
Yeah, who cares about Bill Clinton?
I know about Bill Clinton. What do you know about Bill Clinton?
Bill Clinton is my uncle. What are you going to do about it?
And you had a girl with my baby?
Huh?
You had a girl with my baby?
You're
my girl?
A chump.
You my baby's mama?
You're a chump. Yeah,
you my baby's
right.
mama?
Yeah,
B, what
right,
is this
I'll
guy trying to... B, what is it? You're
well,
so...
You ain't got nothing.
B, you got
so,
my girlfriend pregnant, Howard.
B, yeah,
you
well,
got
I got
girlfriend?
Your girl pregnant. How's that sound?
I know. Century 21. I heard all about you.
What are you going to do about it?
I'm going to smoke me a cigarette.
Oh, yeah. Smoke
Newport.
You. I'll smoke you, boy.
What you know about Newport?
Yeah, what do you smoke?
What do you know about the flying?
Know what I smoke? Cigars right off your wife's ass.
Oh, you a cigar man. Is that what you did to my girl?
Hey, Beto.
Is that what you did to my girl with a cigar?
Beto, is this a guy you had a fight with?
That's right.
He's a chump.
He is.
Howard, you beat
his
black eye.
I beat his ass.
You
beat
and
his
I made him
I thought that nigga out. He's a chump.
All right.
Yo.
He's a chump.
Yo, Beetlejuice.
You're a chump.
Beetlejuice, one question, seriously.
You're a chump.
Are you going to take care of the baby?
You're a chump.
Are you going to take care of the baby?
You're a chump. That's right. It's mine. What are you going to do about it?
With his wife?
That's right. I took over him. She don't love him anymore.
Now the guy's crying. The guy's crying.
She don't want him. That's why she's leaving his ass.
You made this guy cry.
That's right. She leaving him. She ain't got a choice.
You're going to take care of the baby.
Yeah. You ain't got no choice, pal.
All right. Well, this is something
goodbye,
I think you ought to.
That's it. Now I'm coming after you again, Beetle.
Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on. You got a chance. Come on.
Yeah, you don't know about this?
Yeah. Come on. You ain't got a chance. You don't want to have a chance, boy.
4, 5, 6.
You don't have a chance, boy.
3, 2, 1.
You don't have a chance, boy.
All right. Well, that's the end of the Beetle. You showed him. You showed him. And that's why you're a man. That's why you're a real man. You're a real man.
He ain't got it. He ain't got it.
He doesn't have anything.
He ain't got nothing.
You blew him away.
He ain't got nothing. He knows it.
Yeah, but I didn't. I want to. It's going to be so much better right now, I think.
Scott the Engineer made his comedy premiere.
Well, Scott just said to Artie or some of the other guys, why don't you take me out on tour?
He wants to try to make a little extra money, he said. Yeah. And me and Levy thought about it, and this gig seemed like the best fit for Scott's act.
Right. We can go to that first, or do you want to hear Shuley was interviewing AA over the phone for Howard 100 News, and the two of them got into a screaming fight.
Really?
You know, like a typical guy fight where...
Oh, I got to hear that.
They're going to want to kick each other's ass.
They are immediately swearing down, right?
All right. So I'll give you two choices. Which do you want to hear?
I'd rather hear the Scott shit.
You'd rather hear that first?
Yeah,
you're going to hear both. It's just a matter of...
Yeah, it's just a matter of which order.
I don't care about
the Shuley stuff. I always love a fight.
The Shuley stuff is a couple of minutes. You want to go with that first?
Pretty quick.
All right. Okay. Yes,
we want time with Scott.
All right. Yeah,
can I give you the setup on this?
Okay. Go ahead.
The setup is, remember AA was here the last time and was feeling like we weren't paying enough attention. So Howard 100 News offered him a chance to be a reporter for a day. Howard 100 News claims that AA never called him.
Right.
AA claimed he left a message and nobody called him back. So now Shuley's going to do a news story following up on what they're going to do with him. And then it just goes wrong. There's two guys getting pissed at each other.
Do they really go at it?
Yeah, it's just stupid guy shit.
Okay. Here's stupid guy shit from Shuley and AA. And then Artie to the main event. Scott the Engineer, stand up.
Okay, sounds good. I'll get in touch with Benji, and then I'll see if he'll set it up, and then I'll get back to you about it.
Definitely. Get back to both of us in case Brad doesn't get your message.
That's funny, Shuley. You always got to end with a little joke, Shuley. Just make sure you don't cut and choose bits and pieces of this interview like you usually do, Shuley.
That's called editing, and I have to do it with all my interviews.
Yeah. Well, don't make it to your advantage either. Like, just like the other.
Are you threatening me?
No, I'm not threatening you. I'm telling you, do a good report.
You're telling me to do how to do my job now?
Yeah.
How about I tell you how to leave a message properly and stop lying about calling people when you didn't call him.
No, I don't lie, Shuley.
Don't come at me with attitude, bro. I'm doing this to help you out. Shuley, you look like an asshole to everybody here.
No, Shuley, don't do what you do, all right? Because behind
I do what I do, and I get paid to do it. That's why I'm hired here. You do what you do, and that's why nobody's having you on these shows. You understand that? You're coming around with this fucking attitude. You're going to lecture me on how to do my story?
No, I'm telling you, Shuley, don't fucking cut it to make me look like a fucking asshole
Cutting it to make it look like you're you. That's how I'm cutting it. I'm cutting your words to make your words come out just the way they came out of your mouth.
Okay.
If that's something that you don't like, then maybe the news isn't the right thing for you to be doing.
No, Shuley. Don't worry about my right thing for me to be doing or not. Brad's got to give me the opportunity. I'll do it to the best of my knowledge,
all
right?
Okay, that's fine. That's all you got to focus on. Don't worry about what everybody else is doing. Worry about what you got to do.
Okay, Shuley. And you might be in my near future, too, what I got to do. How's that, Shuley?
What's in your near future? What?
You might be in my near future,
doing what
I got to do.
Doing what?
Doing a report on nice little Shuley, all right?
Do a report. Bring it on. You can come to my house anytime.
Yeah. Bro, I don't need to come to your house. I know the real you, bro.
You know where I'm at. Come bring your recorder.
Okay, Shuley.
All right.
I might bring more than a recorder.
You're going to need it, I'll tell you that.
I'm going to bring more than a recorder.
You're going to need it.
Yeah.
Keep threatening me. Watch what happens.
For what? For you?
Keep threatening me. Watch what happens.
Come on, Shuley. You know what I'm going to bring.
Bring it on. I'm here.
Okay.
Little midget.
Yeah, okay.
So they weren't done with each other yet.
Oh,
want to keep
kidding.
Going? Oh, no, this went on. Do you want to continue?
Well, this is so stupid.
Does AA go to Shuley's house?
I don't know. Well, here's the second
installed. Oh, this goes on forever.
Oh, my God.
Are you caught up in the drama?
This is sad that two men, they don't even know how to threaten each other.
Feel free to pull the plug on this bit whenever
Let's
you want.
Let's pull it, because they're ridiculous.
No. You want to hear
You want to hear more, Fred?
I definitely want to hear
more. I love when
more.
Guys fight.
Are you kidding? Neither
so
one of them has come
this
across
is
with a clear-cut threat yet.
That's
I want to see where it goes.
I think they start talking about actually setting up a fight.
Oh, God.
We got to set it up.
But the whole point is, still no. Where did I call you a name, bro?
You insulted me, and I insulted you. That's how it works.
That's how it works. You by name calling. I insult you by calling you any fucking name.
And what about maybe I'm gonna come and do something to you? What about that?
No, I said maybe I'll come and do something with you.
Yeah, and I'll bring a little more than my news recorder. What does that mean?
I know you for years, bro. If you're gonna take that as a personal, like I'm coming to threaten you.
No, I don't like you. I don't like you sitting here telling me how I should edit my fucking news stories. That's not your call. You have no say in it.
Well, then listen, I have a lot of say in it by saying, you know what, don't fucking call and interview me.
And that's fine. And don't expect to do shit on these channels for anyone, because nobody wants to help you when you're a dick like that. When you sit here and you say you're going to do things, you knew I was taping you for the news. You knew, you're mad because the word midget was gone? Go ahead. I'll put a CD in right now. Call me all the fucking names you want.
No, bro, because that's not the way we roll, bro.
Who's we? What are you talking about, we? Who's we?
We're not fucking friends. We're not boys before the fucking whole thing issue. Before we met, this and the other, we never fucking do this kind of shit. We don't make each other look like assholes, like fucking, by all stupid.
Yeah, by telling people how to do their fucking job when you have no idea how to do this job, and you're gonna sit here and tell me how to do it. That doesn't make me look like an asshole.
No, listen to me. I don't like the way you put your little twist.
Then don't fucking do my news stories. Don't tell me you want to do what I tell you last night on the phone. I want to get your side of the story. Isn't that what I told you last night?
And I gave you my side of the story.
Okay, and before I've even edited it and put it on the air, you're going to fucking lecture me about how I do it and how not to do it and how don't leave this in and don't put that in and don't put your little twist on. Let me explain something to you, Double A. I'm not a news reporter. I'm a comedian. I'm a stand-up comic. I have been for many years. What I do is make shit funny, okay? That's how my news stories go.
Okay, fine. So what I'm gonna do is
Boy, Double A's I mean Shuley's out of line. He's like Shuley Corleone.
Mm. What are you saying?
I don't know. Shuley's coming on awfully strong.
Yeah, he's picking a fight with a guy.
I think he's still trying to get news.
No, he's trying
to make something happen.
He's trying to make the news.
Yeah. Right. He's trying to be the news.
But Dan Rather never, bullied
him. Well, he said, I'm a comedian, not a reporter.
Surely, I mean, are you really supposed to sit there and antagonize the fucking people you're interviewing?
No, but, you know, I may have overreacted a little bit, but here's what pissed me off about him. Here's this guy, he comes on your show, he sits on the couch, and all he does is cry. The whole segment he's here about how he wants to be a part of everything here and do something at any level.
But I thought you were a reporter for us. I mean,
so I am a reporter, but we offer, Brad Driver, the news director, offers him a reporter for a day job. This guy, all he has to do is get back in touch with Brad to do this gig, which any true fan of the show would sleep out in the street to do this gig. Forget returning a call. This guy blows him off, and then he lies. He lies to his face. He's going to tell Brad he left him a message, and Brad didn't call him back. It's bullshit, and I got tired of all his bullshit and all his lying, and so I just called him out on stuff.
Right? Why do all of Shuley's news stories revolve around Shuley?
Because Shuley is a comedian, not a reporter.
Thank you, Robin. Somebody was listening to the audio.
I apologize for fucking saying that, what I said to you, but I don't like the name calling.
Don't tell me how to do my fucking job.
I just said that. So now what do you got to do, bro? What do you got to do to make this right? I just apologize.
Well, I'm sorry for calling you a midget, Double A.
Well, I mean, seriously, and don't be putting that either in the report. Either.
See, here you go. Here you go. Again with the fucking, again with the instructions. Again, you don't even hear yourself. You don't even get it.
No,
the guy doesn't want to be called a midget in the news report.
Howard, I may be a half inch taller than him. He's not, what's he so upset about? Is a midget the worst thing you've ever been called?
You remember when you were already called you a hack and you went off the deep end?
Calling him a midget has nothing to do with his business or what he does for a living.
He's just a guy. He listens to the show.
But you know what? I don't see giving him a pass. Oh, he's just a guy. He's just that there's a lot of people out there that would kill for an opportunity guy blows off.
But you're a news guy. You're not supposed to be calling people a midget.
I don't know. I
don't get it.
Listen, they call me names in the news stories, too. Mm-hmm. Double A, let me explain something to you, okay? We've hung out a few times in Vegas. We've hung out here. Between you and I, do you think we're really that close?
Oh, I consider everybody in this whole damn the Howard Stern thing enemies or not, my family. But yeah, I do think it's close. Are you kidding me?
I would say that you and I are acquaintances, not close, dear friends.
Jeez, poor Double A.
Wow. Yeah, now he's being.
We're not a family. What the hell?
It's his delusion.
Exactly. So I'm just letting him know, hey, bro, I'm not your family. And a family, like I told him, it's a two-way street. The other person has to feel their family.
For Shirley's next story, he's going to throw Eric the Midget down a flight of stairs and do other stuff.
Breaking news.
Yeah, all right, Shirley. Thank you. Wow.
Artie
was right. We should have listened to Scott the engineer. Big mistake.
I told you to bail. It was
you were right.
A bad fight.
Ban Mr. Bloodclot. Well, no, you can't ban him. I'm just not going to read it. Now you can ban Mr. Bloodclot. If I see more trolling, it's going to go up to 5 years.